dogs.
Guys, too.
That's that much, yo. Yeah, that's
what that is.
I'm parked up, huh?
Damn, I'm going in. I'm trying to go.
What up, what up, what up, what up, chat? What up, what up? What's up with you motherfuckers? 40 minutes late. You did. We up in here, you know what I'm saying? Apollo is in his joint. Got my nigga Bell in here, you know what I'm saying? Got my nigga Keem in here, Tiny in here, TF is in here. You feel me? What's happening with the chat, man? Y'all make sure y'all smash the like button. Hit the sub if y'all new here, want to stay true here. All my my wrenches in the chat. Yeah, we here though, man. You feel me? Got all our hubbies in here. We coming off of a festive event. You dig? You know, we just here though.
That shit look crazy. I ain't gonna lie.
It looked wild.
That shit look crazy. I ain't gonna lie.
Nah.
What is this?
Where you was at?
Homies ain't hoes.
What happened, Tiny? Why you wasn't there?
That shit look crazy.
I pulled up, cuz.
Oh, you can't get in?
Couldn't get in.
These niggas burnt out,
homie.
Yeah.
You didn't call nobody. If you can't get in, you'll hit somebody. Like, yo, I can't.
Yeah, Tiny acting different, y'all.
Like, I'm thinking I'm somebody out here.
That's that pride.
I'm thinking I'm somebody out here, man. I'm thinking, like, y'all know me, Apollo congregation.
You want a church coat?
wait, so they only know that nigga off of the trench coat? Chat, what up?
God damn, trench coat part of your identity now. That's insane.
Yeah, so this nigga.
That shit burnt out, girl. That shit had me hot.
Yeah, Tiny showed up to an event last night, and bro didn't say nothing to nobody. He just showed up and just was waiting in the front.
He was standing in line.
I went straight to the front, and I'm thinking I'm gonna see somebody I know, but I didn't see nobody I know, so I just was like,
"You lying up for real? You gotta touch him now."
No, I'm serious.
He really pulled up.
All right, yeah.
So why?
All right, why you didn't ask? Okay, but why you didn't? I said what time and where at? You said pull up with Q. You said pull up with Q. I said what time we're at. TF text the address. Nobody said what time. So I just showed up.
So I'm saying, why you call TF when you got there?
Why you never said what time to show up?
What does it matter? Why you call TF when you got there?
Nigga, I told you, I can't just keep relying on y'all to get in places.
And that's why your ass ain't get in.
I gotta be my own identity.
That's it.
You know what I'm saying?
I gotta be my own identity.
So, chat, how the mic sounding right now? Everybody good? All the audio is good?
Niggas didn't let me in. It's cool, though.
How long you stay before you was like,
he's lying, man.
He's lying?
Yeah, he's over here entertaining this bullshit. Man, I'm about to keep playing with you, man.
All right, man. Tiny didn't pull up to this shit, man. That nigga Tiny Hollywood.
You want me to be lying. That's
like
why.
You didn't want to be there. If a nigga don't call and say he outside, he didn't really want to be in there.
You just didn't text back.
Oh, my God. Man. But if you would have did the right thing, Tiny, you would have enjoyed that show, bro. That
man,
shit was,
it looked like it was epic, though. No cap.
It really was.
It looked
dope,
like it
man.
Was epic.
It really was. Shout out my boy Cal Bizanks, bro. That nigga went crazy. Dope event. All the homies came out. All the homies was there. Shout out to all the homies that put up.
And shout out
all the homies that didn't pull up as well, though. The love was in the building. You feel me? Most definitely. Shout out to everybody that was in attendance. You know what I'm saying? Shit was most definitely really,
shout
really
out to all
dope.
The people that couldn't get in.
That's what I'm saying. It was really a crazy situation.
You know, people really couldn't get in, though.
I know. Yeah. I was part of the people.
Yeah, what people was it, like, capacity? It was like me and nobody.
Stupid. You didn't see how it looked?
I did.
Yeah.
Surprised the motherfucking fire marshals didn't pull up in that motherfucker.
Is that how the stage always is? Like, in the middle, or niggas just...
For Boiler's Room, it's similar. It's pretty much like that all the time.
That's fire.
Just like different
how venues? Yeah, just different venues.
Yeah, I caught up to what Boiler Room meant, like, last night. I didn't.
You are lying.
I mean, I just thought it was going to be much cozier.
Nah, it's really like the DJ shit. Like, it's like I did a couple Burlesque Room when Zay performed and like artists performed and shit.
Yeah.
But it's normally based around the DJ and shit like that.
Oh, but I didn't know you're supposed to be soaking, like sweating like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, ain't no AC in that motherfucker.
I think they turn it off or something.
They turn it off for it to be Boilers Room.
They turn it off.
They wait till that motherfucker.
Yeah, it was all Boilers Room for sure.
Probably turn the heater on.
Yeah, make it boil us.
Hot time.
Yeah, no, that's sick though, man.
Turn it up, motherfucker. Something in the what you call it? Refrigerator.
But
when we be a host and get it.
My boy, my boy Cal brought out he brought out Zaywap came out, my nigga Q-Wap came out. Who else came out?
Smino.
Zay came. Oh, you said Zay.
Zay.
Q, Smino. Denzel Curry.
Curry. Shout out my nigga Denzel Curry, bro. Man, this dude was talking about. What's that? He brought up the first Boiler Room. No matter of fact, he brought up the Boiler Room we did together and shit like that. That was actually. We really. Was that you that brought up the Denzel Curry story? Or was that you? No. That said he was outside on. He was talking about that shit. No, I think that was Reason that said that shit. But definitely shout out Denzel Curry, man. That nigga Journey Band, he had a crazy journey to be up in this motherfucker still going crazy like that.
Yeah, nah, he came too.
King, was you supposed to put a wig on last night?
Where?
You supposed to pull up to the Boiler Room shit with a wig on?
Pull up with a wig on?
What the fuck?
Nah, I wasn't supposed to put no wig on.
That's the narrative the people talking about right now. I just seen that in the chat.
They said that I was supposed to pull up and put a wig on.
I heard that yesterday.
What'd you hear?
That you're supposed to pull up with the wig on. Then I just, I forgot about it. Then I seen it right here. The people like, King, where the wig at?
Shit, I gotta find some of those. That's what I said, man. Rest in peace, Granny.
Rest in peace, G-Mons, man.
Them type of wigs is gone. Those like the old good
one.
Wig.
With the
was that that? Was that right the picture here? I sent you? That you was talking about?
No.
Oh, that but.
Yeah, you funny as fuck.
Yeah. I never dropped that, though.
No,
I sent it to you.
No, you didn't drop
so
it.
So don't even act like no fucking weird nigga.
There's multiple pictures. There's multiple pictures.
There's multiple pictures? Yeah, I said that.
Oh, I didn't know.
Hey, if I hit me, I said, you know what? It's like two more of them floating around on the net, man. You know what I mean? I can drop them if I want to. I might drop them. I didn't drop a couple already. I didn't drop them.
Yeah, so, I think the one I seen was on your shit before.
Yeah, I dropped it.
All right, so I got a couple questions then since we're here now.
We're here now.
You didn't think it was going to get here?
Yeah, we did, but I didn't know it was gonna be this early in the
oh,
shit.
Okay, since we're here
but
now,
I knew it was gonna get here, so eventually.
Yeah. That's why I was so quiet when
this
I walked in today.
Huh?
Holler at me. Holler at me.
You said what?
Holler at me.
I had some pride.
Hey,
basically, so you said you used to do that for your cousin?
For my cousin? No, that's how I used to do it for my cousin. You been listening to the Ace Boys?
No, I heard. Like you said, that's, you used to do that for
hey, that was a funny
was.
Narrative,
that
though.
Was funny
that
fun.
Was really a dead end. Who said that? Who the Ace that's Boys is Ace funny Boys, for that?
So what was it, though? So that's because I was kind of confused, like too.
I said when I was younger and shit, like, and it's actually, like I said, it's funnier to me, the story, but when I was younger, yeah, just like I am now, just playing, you know, whatever, me being me. I used to fall through like that with either my granny fit on acting like granny or I come to acting
hey,
like
hey, it's all the homies cousin, audio sounding cool chat.
He was mentally challenged, but you know what I'm saying? He was grown. He was funny as fuck to me. So I used to come through, you know, either acting like him or acting like granny.
With the shit on, okay.
Yeah. So, I was never doing that for him, but that was a,
okay.
I fuck with that take.
All right, so then.
with that take.
Yeah, that's for sure funny because I didn't hear that part. But then, all right, so you said your pops used to trip on you for tickling motherfuckers, right?
Mm-hmm.
So how did he feel about you putting the wig on and doing all that to motherfuckers?
You know, that's what I'm saying. That's why it's a funnier story. So, Pops then went to jail like a couple times and shit or whatever. And this when I was staying with my auntie and then, like my grandma, auntie and cousins. I ain't never did that like at the crib with Pops. I never did that in front of Pops. I ain't never did that in front of Pops.
So he didn't know.
I mean, I'm sure you heard. Yeah, I was like, you know what I mean? I was a character, but I never did that in front of him, though. For sure. I wouldn't even be comfortable to play like that in front of him like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Pops, did you put lipstick on too?
No, I never put lipstick on. No, I never put lipstick on.
Hey, King, Pops was strict?
Nah, he wasn't strict. My Pops was cool. He was cool, bro. Like I said, due to his situation.
God, I got some good questions.
Far as like dialysis and his lifestyle, Pops was cool. He wasn't tripping on me like that. But he was just principally driven. Like, if he see me doing certain shit or acting away or if he see whatever, it was all principle. He see some shit, you correct it.
Yeah. So
the dialysis is cold though.
All right,
he's on that shit for 20 all my life.
He's
strong. Yeah,
sick. So let me. All right, King.
Let
So, all right, let me ask you this then, right? So, you said you used to do that shit when Pops wasn't around.
I wouldn't do that. I didn't do that. I didn't play like that.
When he, you didn't play like that when he was around.
Not like that, no. Not with the Papa not acting like my grandma.
What?
Not popping out acting like my grandma.
Wearing the wig and shit.
Yeah.
Alright, so do you think if you was like a fatherless kid like me, how far you think you would have went, like if your pops never was there though?
How far I would have went? I don't think I would have been. I don't think so. I don't think
you get.
Been.
You get what I'm trying to say.
You trying to say. You trying to say. If I would be like sassy.
Because he put a filter on your sassy.
He trying to ask if you be doing the role playing too.
Yeah, basically.
No, that's why I was crying laughing yesterday. I said, "Oh damn, this right here gonna be funny."
Oh, then you was like, "Niggas gonna go crazy on Saturday."
For sure. For sure. But like I said, once again, I dropped that story. It's like I dropped that story, but for sure I did that. But nah, as I got older, that just wasn't my thing to be doing. You know what I'm trying to say? I was just being fun, having fun for my family, being funny.
I get that part. I get that part.
You know what I mean? 100%. Being funny, for sure, for sure. But it was never like some shit. I wasn't sneaking clothes to school and shit, trying to put this shit on.
But you were sneaking them with your pops gone.
Nah, I wasn't sneaking them with my pops gone. Just I was at granny's house acting like granny.
So when you say acting like granny, what does that... how's that? What
she
is
coming
acting
that
like
motherfucker tripping, like just acting like her. She used to come in the living room tripping, or she come do a look at all the, you know, the kids a certain way, whatever the case may be. Yeah.
Let me hear. What, how you used to
let
do
me,
it?
Let me hear. Hey yo, shout out Tiny though. My nigga be trying to cook his shit down though. He get when he feel like he got a nigga where he want him. No, right here.
How I used to go, okay? Put my grandbaby in the game. That's what they used to say to, I think that was Proud Family. Granny was like, put my grandbaby in the game.
Oh my
for
God.
For sure, used to legit, like, that shit used to be funny. It's still funny to me. Like, it was a funny ass thing. And I never felt no way ever, too. Like, I never even felt no way doing that shit. I didn't feel like I was like, you know what I mean? But I know not to play.
Yeah,
I didn't
know,
play
no
like that.
It was a horror, man. You wasn't like, you didn't have no feeling like this is what I'm supposed to be type
shit. Yeah, because my pops wouldn't have laughed at it, I'm saying, right? So,
he would have whooped your ass with it.
Huh?
He would have whooped your ass.
Yeah, he just would have just, you know what I mean? Just from that era, yeah, he probably would have been tweet. He got hot. We was watching wrestling one day, nigga. I'm so like, once again, just because our relationship, like, he went to jail a couple times and all that shit, and whatever. Sometimes the way we bonded was just funny to me. So we get into the wrestling stage, he watching shit. And I called a nigga, I fuck around with some Booker T shit, and I'm like, what's up, son, sucker? You know what I'm saying? That nigga went cold on me. He went cold on me. It's like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I ain't getting no whooping or nothing right there, though. He just went so cold on me. His energy,
yeah.
It just, yeah, he got hot though, he got at me, like, don't even call me no sucker, you know what I mean, whatever the case may be, but, so, yeah, I just, certain shit I wouldn't play with.
Calling an older nigga sucker is like calling niggas of our era weirdos.
Man,
I
might call a nigga stitch.
Yeah.
Yeah, nah, for sure.
Older, especially an OG nigga, like sucker in the 70s, 80s type.
Yeah, that's sucker, come on, sucker.
Sucker.
That's John Turkey edition. That's right up in
dog, I passed my pops, that's what I'm saying. Listen, one time again, I'm living with my grandparents and shit. My grandma, I mean, aunties, cousins, so. All right, this is out of pocket, that's what I'm trying to say, like. Nigga pants my pops. Y'all know the part.
Hey, bro.
Hey, Ken, what you mean? Somebody went to your pops in.
No, I did. Listen, but this is the story I'm trying to tell you. He was high. He don't even play like this. But to what you saying? It's to what you saying, right? Like, yeah, I guess like. They was playing like that over there, and my cousin's in the house. You know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
So, yeah, that Pops is a filter, because, yeah, he got high. Anyways, this nigga right there on Atlantic, y'all know the apartments across the street from Jordan High and shit.
Yeah.
We got us apartment, nigga, right to
you really be moving around, though, for you to be over there, though.
Yeah, right to the street. The door right to the street, you know what I'm saying?
Like the court is not even a court, it's like the curb.
Hey, right there. And
you funny,
and some
man.
People about me right across from some shit. Anyways though, that nigga posed up. He fresh out of jail and shit.
And you passed the nigga fresh out of jail.
Hey, look, this is funny. That nigga posed up, just kicking it. You know what I'm saying? Getting a good breeze. Nigga,
nigga, I feel like he over there posed up.
A real nigga like this.
Dude. Yeah, yeah.
Hey, dude. I pissed this nigga. What I know, where I got hot at. I mean, where I knew I fucked up at for sure. I thought niggas had some drawers on. I'm on Kaepernick like, damn, it's over. Hey, yo, dude, hey, I'm just knowing that it's over, right? Type shit.
Hey, yo, you Kaepernick, nigga. So that mean your face was to ass cheek?
No, it's my face to ass cheek.
You said you like, Kaepernick, go to D.
Yeah, nigga, I'm my nigga, but listen. That's what I'm trying to say, but you funny, though. But what I'm saying is,
and though, that's what you meant, too, though. That's yeah, Kaepernick. Yeah,
yeah. Oh, my like, God.
Like, I really...
Hey, you I are too much into that, right?
Anyways, homie. Now he, my pops, an older what man, the dog. Fuck? Older man for sure. And Chat. This nigga get the backpedaling so fast. Nigga did a back like a he rolled, did a flip and shit. Got up, running. He running
studio.
So he like getting himself together. He just lost, dog. Hey, nobody playing with him like that. You know what I'm saying? So nigga really lost.
You are.
Hey, dog, but I'm hurt. I'm crying so damn bad. I'm crying. I can't even stop laughing. Nigga, when that nigga ran into the bedroom. He ran into the bedroom, pulling his pants up. That nigga took about a good 3 minutes to come out, bro. He come out quiet. I'm in that room. I'm in the living room crying so hard, nigga. He come out that motherfucker, dog, so hot.
That's crazy.
He put the went under the sink, got the coldest extension cord, the orange one. Extension cord, that shit wrapped that motherfucker around
Depot
his neck.
Motherfucker.
Right, for sure. He owed me. Now he snapped. What the fuck you mean? I'm laughing, thinking it's funny. Fuck you mean, my motherfucker? Pants, you know what I'm saying? Put my pants on, my dick out of it. Like he feeling embarrassed like a motherfucker. He snapping on me loud. That nigga, that nigga gave me a cold ultimatum, homie. He gave me a cold ultimatum, but don't worry about it. I'm even gonna tell the rest of that story. He gave me a cold ultimatum, dog. It was a whooping or embarrassment, like, you know what I mean?
Oh, you gotta go through the
that
same embarrassment.
That nigga had to walk down the street naked, care.
Put the wig on and walk down the street naked, dog.
No cap, I'm telling you, homie. Nigga said the whooping. All right, because he was so embarrassed. He said, only way, you feel me, is if, like, he told me that he going to either have the bunny hop from the end of the hallway all the way back to the door. You know what I'm saying? Just how you had me. Or you take his ass up, you know what I'm saying? If it's show, dog, I bunny hop.
Damn.
The whole shit, homie. And he let me do that shit. Got at me, embarrassed me like a motherfucker, dog. But I was not taking that whooping with that orange extension cord, homie.
Damn.
No, he was mad off the orange extension cord?
Huh?
He about to whoop your ass.
Oh, he's right now. He wanted to, but I think he really, in his eyes, he's gonna hurt me. Like, yeah. Dog, you just, I don't know what you want. He feeling a little like.
What made you do that?
That's what I'm really trying to figure
that's
out.
That's what I'm saying. That's why it's fun. That's why it is.
That's not funny, though.
Yeah, I'm just playing.
That's not funny, though.
Yeah, I'm just playing. Like, you know what I'm saying? Really, like, playing, but.
That you don't know.
Huh?
Like, people that you just sit down meeting, like, at school, that shit, like, class clown type nigga.
Yeah.
I mean, let me put this cheese on your chest. Paul. Like.
Yeah, nah, for sure.
Damn,
sometimes
that's
I play too much. That's why I said I get it. When some people get hot at me, sometimes I know I play too much sometimes. For sure.
Dang. Yeah, that's some wild shit though, King. I ain't gonna even lie.
That's funny. That's funny as fuck.
That definitely was funny. Shout out to you for that story. Yeah.
Oh man, that's crazy.
Yeah, man. Rest in peace, Pops, man. For shit show. You dig? So, in other news, man. What's up with my nigga Smacky, man? They saying bro supposed to lose his foot or some shit. What's that about?
Nah, we ain't gonna.
Say that though, huh?
Yeah, we only putting positive tough, energy man. Out prayers, there. Well, I'm only putting
prayers,
positive
prayers out
there.
To Smacky, man.
Yeah, for sure, bro. Prayers to Smacky, man.
Prayers out to Big Deal too, man.
Most definitely. Prayers to Big Deal, my nigga Smack, man.
All mental.
Both of them niggas, man, get well soon. It's definitely all mental, man. You just got to keep your head in the right space. Also, niggas got to also hold these hospitals accountable too, though, and shit like that. You dig what I'm saying?
They'll definitely tell you anything.
Yeah, they'll definitely tell you anything. Thing for sure. Yeah, would you say no belt? You gotta speak me up. Let me see.
I think this is a high tech mic. I'm like,
nah,
they definitely tell you anything.
Yeah, the hospital's tricky, man. I remember I bust a window I bust a window right here when I did all this stupid shit. And I went through the hand specialist. Mm-hmm. And they sold this motherfucker up with like 3 pieces of glass still in it. My shit was tore up. That shit was just tearing shit up when they like I'm doing like this and shit. That shit was ripping shit up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, that's wicked. That's really, really some wicked shit though. You dig? But shout out, man. Shout out to my nigga Smack though, for sure, man. That nigga gonna be up out that motherfucker soon. Back up on back on Fig soon, man. That's what niggas definitely hoping for. You dig?
They probably have to really do some type of protest then. I don't know whoever got an update. We talking about it on camera though, but if it is that ugly.
We just talked to mom right now.
Mm-hmm.
Talked to her. She gave us a little bit of update. Talked to Smacky. He was supposed to hit me back, but he was talking to the doctors.
Yeah.
They trying to get it together. They trying to figure it out for sure.
Yeah. That's a fact.
Smacky trooping it out.
Yeah, bro, definitely in there trooping it out, man. That hospital shit could be like, that's just a super depressing situation to be in, just being in the hospital itself.
Yeah,
just,
they gotta be strong in there, man.
For sure. For sure.
They gotta be strong in there, for sure.
Hell yeah.
Stay okay.
Let me see. I'm gonna read a couple of these motherfucking booper chats before we holler at my nigga Bell. We definitely got my nigga Bell in here, man. We're gonna figure out these stories and see what these if these motherfuckers got some truth in them. You know what I'm saying? This nigga got some legendary story. I don't know what's going on with bro. But
forgot about that goddamn cat.
Yeah, my nigga El Nano sent 499 TF in the kitchen like, hey Betty Crocker, huh? Let's get to that. Blame Kansas. Niggas really trying to hit that.
Huh?
Oh,
you smoking my foot, bro.
Shouts out to Doggy Dog, man.
Yeah.
Blame Kansas out right now. Go tap in and run it up.
Yeah. Shout out my nigga News. News came through with $2 and said, Keem Wana, man. How was that trip last night?
That motherfucker was insane.
And shout out Mr. Mushies. Yeah,
that's King. Pocket.
Y'all niggas, bro, I don't know how y'all niggas able to do that.
How many squares you at?
Only
2. But this nigga was out. He was at the function though, TF. You able to function off this shit?
I still need your number.
Man, I was off a whole bar last night. In the function.
Oh shit. Yeah, y'all niggas different. I gotta go. I be segregating myself off that shit and go be dozy. Oh God.
I never really fucked around, but I am though one of these days.
Yeah.
I niggas just be like, damn. You just hear so many stories like niggas tripping out and shit like that.
I was floating though, but shit was just intense though. You know, nigga heartbeat. I'm hearing all the heartbeats and all that.
I'm hearing all the heartbeats.
Yeah, you hear your
heartbeat is like your body. Like you hearing it, actually hearing it.
And I'm the type of motherfucker, if I'm high, I gotta be present. Like for real. Yeah. Now I gotta talk.
Yeah.
Cause that's the only way I'll be knowing I'm present. I get too quiet and shit. About like, 18, you I got like 18 personalities. Real shit. Mine go crazy.
Yeah, I don't know how you was able to do that shit, Kimmy Kim. You were, y'all niggas.
Nah, probably because only took 2.
Oh, yeah.
But I almost caught a panic attack when that nigga Terrell, I thought he took 5 before that day, yesterday.
Oh, yeah.
I ain't know he didn't take none that day. When I heard that, I'm like, oh, that's out of 5.
That shit be bullshit, I mean. Nah, that shit definitely be bullshit, for sure. I can't, y'all can take, I'm lucky got a cool little tolerance for that shit, though. I ain't gonna even cap a nigga be getting out of his mind with that shit, though.
I ain't had none since the live show, okay? How you feel off the shrooms? Floating, yeah. Shit be bright.
Yeah, that shit be dope be when a nigga be driving. That shit be all motherfucking Star Wars behind the wheel.
He said niggas be all Star Wars.
They turn into Tron, huh?
Yeah, because you know, you got the white lights coming this way and the red lights in front of you. Then you got, especially like sliding down Sunset, you know, they got the TVs on the wall and shit like that.
Yeah.
With all the other bright lights going on, all the stupid traffic.
How much you got to take to feel like that, though?
It depends on your power levels.
If you 2 for sure if you're a rookie and you want to go there.
Nah,
like,
just,
like,
just
what you mean? Like the bars like this? Like a piece of the bar? Like a Kit Kat? Or like
I think I think it come with like 12 of them motherfuckers on there, right?
Matter of fact, the night, yo party?
Yeah.
I was off 3 bars.
3 whole ones?
3 whole bars. A pack of gummies.
I'm trying to get this shit right for the morning.
But that was like throughout the whole day, though. You know what I'm saying? From the skating ring. from Skate Ring, then we went to Terrell House, then we went to your shit. So like over the, that whole course of time, nigga ran through 3 bars and a pack of gummies.
Yeah, cause you gave me something that night too.
Oh yeah.
I mean, you just like, this all I got.
Gave you the last of
them. Yep, he said, this all I got. I'm like, hurry.
Yeah, I gave you the last of them.
Yeah. I think I turned it down.
No, it's good. It's going to last. Should do it. But, yeah, man. So, y'all niggas, what y'all think about my nigga Reezy Reez album? Porch is out right motherfucking now.
Porch is out, motherfucker. Fuck with the album. I personally fuck with it. For sure, for sure.
You fuck with it?
Yeah, I think it's dope. Yeah. I worked out to that shit the other day. Sure. You know, if you can work out to an album, that's I feel like it's a solid album.
Yeah. That shit is solid project, it's for sure, for sure. I'm still dissecting that motherfucker, too.
It's definitely solid.
Hell yeah, man. Shout out my nigga
still dissecting? You listen to it?
Nah, I ain't hear it.
Yeah, nah. I fuck with it. For sure, for sure. I'm trying to see. You know what I mean? I like Family First record a lot, too.
The intro?
No.
You said family,
with Kaylin, yeah, okay, with Kaylin, Macari, and Sir.
I like that one too.
I like gang shit a lot.
You just play it all the way through?
I play it all the way. Yeah, when I'm listening to an album, for sure, yeah.
Especially that's how
if
I did
the artist wanted to be heard that way, yeah, for sure.
Do you repeat?
Though? Some artists don't. They don't care. They play like, they make it like that.
Also, like, you think now people make their albums to be on shuffle?
Yeah, for sure.
Man,
hell yeah.
Like the artist,
what you mean they make it to be on shuffle?
Like the artist,
recording process is on shuffle.
It's not a cohesive project. Basically,
it's a playlist.
It's a playlist.
Yeah, it's just a mood, like
a DJ Khaled type joint.
You just put on shuffle. There ain't no story to it. Ain't nothing that's attached to it. Ain't no like.
Yeah.
It's just like, man, look.
So they don't care. They feel like niggas. Yeah. Throw the dice out there. I got something for everything.
Until you find a song that you love, and we gonna turn that motherfucker to the single.
Nah, for sure. Yeah, shout out Big Tony, man. That intro is dope, though, man. That nigga Reason can rap his ass off for shit show, man. I'm definitely happy for bro. You did. Got his project out. You know what I'm saying? It's really, really. I'm fucking with it, man. Shout out to the gang, man. Shout out to the gang. TDE is def gearing up for a lot of releases. It's looking like you dig. Let's see. Hold up. My nigga AB23 saying 1999. What's the difference between Adam and Terrell? The second MacWap said to Moose that he was being burnt out, Terrell quickly said, let him cook. And later in the episode, Terrell told Reason that he wanted him to crash out. Yeah. Niggas making content, bruh.
Is the difference between
Adam and Terrell is Adam is thriving on black violence and shit like that. Yeah, and Terrell is a black man. This nigga was just doing what he was supposed to do, asking the right questions, doing what he was supposed to do as an interviewer. You get what I'm saying? He's not bringing these niggas in here to start beef with niggas on both sides of with like gangs and shit like that or stuff like that. You get what I'm saying? He was just asking the questions. That was right there.
Yeah.
So y'all feel like wanting people to crash out is
cooking?
Yeah.
What's crash out?
I'm talking about.
I say yeah, but what's crash out?
Yeah.
Well, but my answer to that is yeah.
Huh?
My answer to that is yeah, though.
But yeah, if he's able to get somebody to react the way he wants to, that's basically what he was doing. He wanted him to react a certain way to the questions, and he did.
Okay.
Nah, I wasn't just speaking about him in general. I was speaking about, I'm speaking in general.
Me neither. Yeah.
Like, I feel like, when motherfuckers crash out, that's content.
Yeah, Terrell, that shit is totally different from what Adam do, to be all the way honest with niggas. That's totally different. But shout out to everybody that's in this content space, man. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely. And I mean, if you do want to keep it 100, he was around Adam though, so I'm sure he did learn some shit from
picked up traits.
Yeah, just by being, I picked up traits from all three of y'all, just being around naturally. So I mean, I wouldn't rule it out, but the difference is, like you say, he's not bringing beefs up there and shit like that, and he's black,
he ain't antagonizing nothing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Like it ain't gonna end in like Adam. It's been like the whole that platform. It's been people that go up there and it don't end. You know, they end the whole totally completely different way. You feel me? We actually got some quality music out of this, however it turned out. So, and I feel like in this journalistic space, because that's what y'all are too. When you bring people up here to interview, I turn it to journalists. Y'all want to know stories, information about people. You wanna get some type of emotion, because you know emotion is reaction. So you want to get some type of emotion out of people.
Low key, that is. So it's like a damn to like get down or lay down, because they say it's like, you go give me these answers. That's the reason why we sitting down, like on some open shit or whatever. I'm getting that exclusive. You go give me the answers, for sure. Or you can go to somebody else and like, they don't plan on getting the answer, but fuck that, I want the same answer the Oprah's gonna get. We all want the same shit.
Yeah. Not for sure.
We want information. We want information.
Get everybody down, lay down.
We want information.
Want information first too.
Yeah,
that's. But you're supposed to care though. You definitely supposed to care.
Oh,
so.
I could have turned it off, nigga. You said turn it down.
Oh, no, I'm just turning it off right now. Just it should be quiet a little bit.
Yeah, you
better
to do that. What's the name?
Man, it's a button.
You definitely supposed to care though. I'll say that.
But say it again, my fault.
You think he don't care? You think like, T-Roll don't care?
I believe he do care. Yeah. I'm just saying, as far as generally.
Okay, yeah.
So wait,
you supposed to have like you supposed to have your own, you supposed to create your own boundaries. Like I'm not gonna go there.
Yeah, I mean, unless you want to go there. Like, depending on what type of platform you got.
Yeah.
Like if you know turning your back and seeing what's going on, when it's repercussions and shit. Consequences to like something that led strictly from your platform, that wouldn't be a good look either. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So what you saying is, y'all would stop me. I'm a funny ass nigga.
Oh God, I see
you
that.
What you think? What you think, though? Should we just?
Yeah, that's your observation.
But so
I feel like that's in that situation for me being an artist. You feel me? And trying to get on these platforms is like now you had a and now it's different. Now the roles are reversed. The one thing about them tables, they always turn. So yeah. Now where niggas couldn't get access, you could go get access because it seemed like it's like more of an open door policy.
Wait. Give some more context to what you're saying.
I'm saying that these type of platforms, like shit, it's the tables turn. It's like I could come up here and be like, call y'all, be like, hey man, what's going on? I want to come chop it down, sit down with y'all. You couldn't do that in some of these different type of spaces.
Like before, what spaces?
Before is this. Shit, different type of radio spaces.
Also, LA, basically, the like LA radio wasn't letting like the local artists come up there.
I'm not gonna say that. Cause
so what you saying?
I feel like I say this. I feel like it's still relationship based though.
Yeah, relationship based.
So that's the same on any platform. Yeah. Cause it's still motherfuckers that probably will say they couldn't even come on here, not like that, but like oh niggas don't really want me to come on there or something like that. And that don't even be the case. It's probably just really relationship based. Yeah. You know what I mean? So it's just a more broken down version. Yeah. And we seeing more people able like to do this shit.
I also feel like a lot of motherfuckers be in their own head too. You know, to where it's like I don't even know how to reach out or even reach out and be like, yo, I've been trying to come up here forever, but I just didn't know how to tap in or you know what I'm saying? So I guess it do go back to relations.
Yeah, it's definitely.
Because you definitely gotta have that link.
If you can't be in your head.
Exactly. If you ain't in that right space to just tap in, like, yo, what's up? You know,
But how you know when it's green to tap in? When do you know?
You just gotta put
pride. That's the come with tapping in.
You just gotta put the pride to the side and reach out.
Because you tell me a lot about myself like that. Like, bro, you got resources. You should just reach out. But I'd be like, damn, when is it? Okay, and I can hit. I feel comfortable enough to be like, hey, what's up? What's good?
Mm-hmm. But nigga never know.
Yeah.
But also, radio stations is more guidelines. I mean, of course they could pull whoever up there they want to because they got their time slot or whatever. But when I feel like this shit is more freedom. You know what I'm saying? You don't gotta go through the higher ups and shit like that.
And that's where I'm in with like the tables turn because it's just like in the music space where. You had to do this, and this to put the song out. Then SoundCloud come, and then they fuck up the whole space. Now you can just rap
right
now.
What's that word for this shit? Disruption.
Yeah, disruption.
Yeah.
Disrupting.
Yeah. So then it's like, if you don't know how to adjust, you're going to be scrambling, then you're going to start getting to your head, then you're going to start feeling like, oh, it's over with for me.
Right, but yeah. This shit politics too, though, because it's like what y'all saying for is people, artists going to radio stations.
I got you, Pete.
People still doing for us, like podcasts be having they politics and shit, and don't be wanting already. Don't be wanting you to go to that podcast.
What you mean, like artists or just like?
Yeah, because it's like to me, it's kind of like ingenuine conversations because that's why I be seeming scripted a lot of times. Like I wouldn't, to me, it shouldn't matter what platform you go to. You go over here, go over here, but you want the same thing I want.
Yeah.
So that's the reason why it's politics. Other than that. Hey, he could pull up over
that's
there.
That's actually, to me though, Kim, like, not to cut you off with that shit, but I feel like niggas that had that look out on, that perspective on shit, I just feel that they make weak content. Because it's obviously, but you about to just regurgitate and make.
You gonna get the same story these other motherfuckers just got.
That depend on the questions you asking.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, depends on the questions like,
that means you just asking the same questions. Yeah.
But that's exactly. But that's what I'm saying. Like.
Our people might be, my fault, not to cut you off, man. Like, yeah. Depending on who you sit down with may alter how you answer the question.
Exactly.
You feel me? If I sit down with y'all, I'm going to be, of course, more open because I feel like this is more of, like, for me.
Yeah, for sure.
It's
yeah.
Like, y'all, like, damn it, y'all my family. You feel yeah. Me? Now, somebody else to come up here that don't really know y'all but y'all cool with, you might not get the same answers. And if that's like if I go do a sit down at a radio station, I don't really know these people, so I'm going to be a little bit more contained. If they ask me a question, I'm going to try to spin
polished.
It. Yeah. I'm try to spin it. It's like, nah, I ain't going to answer that on here, y'all. You feel me?
Right. Nah, for sure. Definitely, man.
So, yeah, then it go back to who getting them exclusive interviews.
And I think that's what
who
was.
Getting them exclusive answers and questions and details.
The Bobby bitch.
What Bobby bitch?
But she not even giving exclusive. She just getting her a cold perspective. That's yeah. It.
But that's the white.
That's
lucky. What I'm saying. Yeah. Both okay. Arguments. Like she getting the same interviews, but she's not having the same questions, or it's a whole different take. That ain't even the bitch personality.
That's tight.
You get what I'm saying? Yeah, like that's not even the personality of, like that's what make that tight. Like,
but that's when the disruption comes in, cause it's like yeah. Now
exactly she is a disruption. Yeah. She is a disruption. Yeah. A lot of motherfuckers is hating why they not doing nothing for the culture.
Yeah.
Doing interviews for the niggas in the culture.
Yeah.
Because it's still the interview yeah. For the culture, it don't matter. Like yeah.
Who doing it, who get yeah. It.
All you gotta go do is just you can anybody who feel that way.
And that go back to your content, Matt. Like mm-hmm. Niggas putting out weak content.
That's all it is.
Yeah.
Nah, but it's still, but if you go look at anybody, and see, if it's your peer hating or whatever, it's somebody that been here hating, possibly hating.
Yeah, I've been noticing a lot of peers hating, and these the older niggas.
But what, how you know if it's actually hating, though?
Because
are they looking at it like...
They haven't tapped into the youth, to the niggas that they feel like they in competition with, to give them advice and shit like that. I'm starting to see what Terrell been talking about. Mm-hmm. I ain't gonna cap.
What Terrell been talking about?
That these niggas ain't reaching out to us when he said he been DMing niggas. You're a funny nigga with Pete. How you say he DM'd all them niggas?
Yeah.
And they not answering. He looking for answers. He got questions.
Is that entitlement?
What is entitlement?
I'm saying like, is that entitlement? I'm asking.
That's not entitlement. That's a nigga that's looking for answers.
That's looking nigga looking for answers.
You not.
But kind of like what you were saying earlier though, right?
Nigga, this nigga.
If you sitting down across from a motherfucker and you already know he really just saying. I'm waiting on them tables to turn.
Yeah.
That's a different type of nigga though.
Yeah. What kind of nigga is that?
I don't think that you don't wait for that. It's just progression and naturally happens.
All right, but even when the tables turn though, right? What I'm saying, like, cause I get it. Like I done said it before. Like niggas just have this type of chip on their shoulder when they say that the tables always turn.
Oh, you think?
But then
that's
what
like
happens when it's your yeah when it turn? Like, are you gonna be the same person that you thought was like?
Cause
block you.
Yeah, I feel you. Cause your situation changed when the tables turned.
Yeah.
Now you in that position.
Exactly.
So what you gonna do when you got the power?
Exactly.
What you gonna do when you at that table?
Yeah.
Shit. Yeah.
That's what it boils down to relationships.
Yeah. But paying it forward. You gotta pay it forward.
No, you're supposed to pay it forward.
That's the perfect answer. Paying it forward.
You gotta pay it forward.
But you can't pay it. But then again, to your point, King, too, like you can't pay it forward to everybody. And then if you a nigga that gets skipped when the tables get turned. Do you feel bitter or you be like, fuck it, it ain't my time yet, let me just keep working?
I always feel like it's
Cause that's happening.
The only issue I had in life was not. I blame my parents.
No, not you. I'm just saying. Like I was being.
No, I'm just saying. But like, yeah, I'm self.
So y'all make sure y'all smash the like button on that chat.
Like I get it. Shout out. I don't feel like I'm owed this thing.
Yeah. You have no entitlement.
And but I feel it though. When I know I'm, you know what I'm saying? It's mine, it's mine.
Yeah.
It ain't about owing nothing. Who owe it to me?
Yeah.
I owe it to myself. That's how I feel. I owe it to myself.
Yeah. Facts.
Do y'all think I seen somebody in the chat ask this, and that was like lucky a good question. Do y'all think what's her name? Bobby Adolf? Do y'all think she's like a like a organic traction she's building? Or is she a plant?
I don't know where she come from. Where she come from? Anybody know?
I could say she did an interview with Funny Marco and it jumped off.
Yeah, that was the first.
That's what set her off.
But interview for is what though? Like that was her first interview.
He interviewed her, or she was interviewing him. It was one of them. But they sat down together and it was what funny. It is now.
He was like, why you sat living in an apartment?
Yeah, it was like he made the good. Funny Marco turned her up. You get what I'm saying? So with that, I mean, I think it's they seen everybody else seen the good humor in it.
Yeah,
and just going like, oh, let me go from here.
Cause not everybody interview gonna look tight. I seen Tigers.
I didn't see that one.
Yeah, that was none of them. I just keep seeing the clips. That wasn't the same as everybody else.
Nah.
Who interview?
The Tiger one with it. It didn't. It wasn't the same. Yeah. It really wasn't the same. But
I mean, shit, everything ain't gonna be a score.
Yeah. It was him. Like you were saying, everybody not gonna be comfortable like sitting in front of everybody.
Let me ask you this though, right? Because it's big shout out my this shit. Period. That's what the radio's been going through, and that's kind of like what streaming podcasting is trying to do too. That's why I say it's politics and this.
Yeah.
So right now, if labels and shit, just like you said, you can hit us and everything. And pull right up, right? All right, boom.
But it took a minute for me to get that comfortable, though. I will give that content to it.
I'm
here now, yeah.
Now, but labels is like making sure one of they artists is there every week now, every week.
Yeah.
They paying. So what would we do then? Would we still trying to, would it be that easy for bro or anybody to pull up? Or now you taking the, you know what I'm saying? The marketing dollars, the system dollars, and it's gonna seem like a lot to us, nothing to them, but that's gonna right back into how this shit be like programming.
But then
so niggas be doing raw interviews, and then now the labels is just paying, like, nah, we going over there. You know what I'm saying? Even if we gotta pay, we going over there.
So then what you're saying? How can a nigga come up here now?
No relationship or nothing.
Yeah, no relationship or nothing.
Because the label's paying for it.
Yeah, because you, yeah.
Y'all think that's.
But that's a hard job, I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Like
yeah. But then y'all filter. Y'all
I was gonna say.
Sit down and be like, we want him, we don't want him, we want him.
You can still not, you don't have to accept every dollar sent your way. Damn. You get what I'm saying? And you can still also and still continue to interview the niggas you fuck with.
That's all I'm about to say. I feel like it's enough days in a week.
I'm making so cold. Peep this up.
Take up all them slots. That's what this shit is.
No, but here go where you. Here go the curveball. You bring your people on there with these niggas. Now you got people, your niggas meeting the artists.
Yeah, no, for sure. That's
the curveball. That's how you got to do it.
Yeah, you definitely got to do it. But that's even
like still invite you. Just get political.
Now we gonna have Bell here with Rocky.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Like that. That's how you bridge. That's really.
That'd be fire.
That's how you bridge the gap right there.
Like that's fire.
No, for sure. Definitely.
That's ways around it. It's definitely ways around it.
It's ways around it.
That's something you got to stand on though, because it get political quick.
Yeah. And it's easier for again.
Because Rocky may not.
Be like, who the fuck is Bill?
Peep here go to twist too though. And with them kind of moments, it'd be like it'd still be organic. Cause you get what I'm saying? Cause like we already in this mix of niggas and shit. You get what I'm saying? So it'd still be the comfortability would still be there because everybody still like just say if it was Rocky, like I do know this nigga. So he gonna still be comfortable being himself with this motherfucker. Mm-hmm. And then if I have a nigga like just bailing this motherfucker, he gonna still be comfortable. So niggas gonna still be able to, you get what I mean?
Yeah.
That kind of shit.
If you don't know Rocky though.
Oh, if I don't know Rocky,
yeah.
Then shame on Rocky. He better.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. You're right. He's not coming in.
Now I'm playing with somebody's whole business just by trying to incorporate do this organic shit. You know what I mean?
Y'all filter it out though. I mean, y'all still.
No, but I certainly. That's something you gotta stand on. So an artist already know. More than likely, they gonna have some like they know that that's the brand. Like
yeah,
you feel me?
Yeah.
You just got to stand on it though.
Yeah, like you said, it's what they call it. It's the intro, the IP.
Yeah.
Like this is y'all IP.
Yeah.
Y'all don't have to. Y'all don't. Y'all not. It's not this. The Apollo moving forward is not contingent on advertising dollars.
Yeah.
The advertising dollars will help it move, like, you know, will jump it or put y'all in a different space. But nigga, however y'all want to design it or set it up, it's y'all IP. So yeah, if this is what, like Keem said, if this is what we doing up here, this is what we doing. You either like it or love it. Or, you feel me?
That's hell it. Yeah, man. I'm about to let me see. We got my nigga Young D. He's in 499. Denzel Curry had one of the hardest albums in 2022. He underrated. Tell him pull up to the Apollo. Yeah, we're gonna make that dev. We're gonna make that happen for sure, man. Shout out to my nigga Denzel Curry.
Yeah, inside the bottom.
Max Millie 85 sent $2. Keem role play cross dress and real life drag king. Gazaboo sent $1.99. Keem put on the granny bloomers too. R.I.P. G Moms. Eminem sent $1.99. Almighty Suspect is top five corniest rapper alive. Shout out Almighty. D Cheney sent $4.99. I'm drinking tea. Tres Gracion too. Yeah, man. Shout out to my
Tres
nigga.
Tres Gracion.
Mine Resposado though. Shouts out to the Apollo. Yes, sir, Ski. Big Baller Brand sent $1.99. Keem was all too wrong. Okay. Keem was all too wrong fool. Wesley Snipes of this.
Oh, shit.
The chat comedy, bruh. Shakai said $4.99. So Keem is Mr. Child. Let's get to that. That nigga Keem said he wasn't Mr. Child the other day,
bro. Mr. Child. Y'all believe the granny story, believe I'm not Mr. Child.
But yeah, y'all niggas are stupid as fuck. Lord A sent $5. OG Suicide, funny for that quit video, because let's just be real. Don't nobody give a fuck. Lord A, shout out to you, man. Shout out OG Suicide. My nigga Big sent $4.99. What's up with Ack and Scissor stuff? Joe said somebody called in for that number. Huh?
I said Joe said that?
Yeah. That's funny as a motherfucker, man. Act burnt out. Yeah, deaf niggas is deaf niggas called in on that nigga. For shit show. But shout out my nigga Joe, shout out my nigga Scissor. Boris sent $4.99. Show was dope. Mac was what? Keem dropped my phone. I tried to run down on TF for some merch, but he skated off. I flew in from Texas. Shout out to Apollo. Shout out my
nigga
Boris.
What's his name? Boris?
Yeah.
Yeah. I met bro last night.
You met that nigga?
He texted me today. What's happening, my boy? I'm gonna hit you back.
Shout out my nigga that guy. He sent $1.99. Smack got a hit up. Gotta hit the Hoover hop now. Y'all niggas stupid. Joseph C.A. sent $9.99. Top track 5 and 11. Shout out Reason. Davon Steen sent $1.99. Shout out Bell Streetwear song of the summer each last year.
Good looking.
Maximus sent $1.99. Terrell was unprepared and was throwing shade at times. Yeah, that nigga Terrell burnt out. B Thompson 199. I ain't gotta be the man. I can play from the back. Pause.
Oh, that's
bro, you niggas ain't hot.
Man.
Oh yeah, cut the Uber back on, Tiny.
That's a bar. That's
I'm trying
bar.
To figure that motherfucker out.
Nigga over here, whoop.
Energy saving,
for real.
Let me see. That's burning up, world. I ain't gonna even catch
that. Got the lights on, nigga, and this motherfucker feeling like he won.
Dictator, look at this nigga. What's his name? Got the fan locked in on him.
Fan just on him, like.
Truth in like a rotation.
Let me put more truth in the detail. I'm sitting up in here in the hot box with the whole heater coming from out this computer. Let's get to that.
Heater?
Yeah, you know the computer be hot. It's all heating here.
Uh-huh.
The truth in those details.
Put your socks on,
bro. Put your socks on.
Your feet like this. The toes do it like this next to the heat thing.
Frito-Lay edition.
Hey, yo. Hey, how y'all feel about ladies night playing with the homies? Like, what's up with that?
I think
talking about we don't be having females over
just,
here.
Another and one then, of them, what we were just talking about. Like, motherfuckers just, you know, probably want to haul over here, don't know how to tap in.
That's what I'm saying. Or that's just not a safe space over there. They keep getting tired of pun making them dance.
Yeah.
I think dance. I get that. Dance.
Yeah.
Dance. Oh, we just got a sub. Dance.
Yeah. Hey, that's exactly
and
what
And don't
is.
Know, dance.
Yeah, because he wasn't even there. He threw still that making narrative. Him dance. Yeah, he threw that narrative. I'm like, oh, okay. So you making plays behind the scenes. You got Illa up there. Oh, man, my bad.
You got, hey, y'all, not too much on my niggas.
Yeah, what y'all doing to the girls, man? I love y'all. Y'all got at me, man. I don't know why they got at me like that.
I only did that because she was sitting in the front. She was sitting in the front, you know what I'm saying? So, she knows since you going to take pun seat and quarterback that, I had to.
But why y'all saying pun did that, though? Did he say something? He sent a super chat in, and that's how that question got up, got brought up?
Nah, you know he, that was pun worm said, egghead yeah, ass.
Pun did, pun
do dance!
Pun was in the chat.
Oh, okay, okay.
Pun, and he pun said, I just got a text message, dance! The sun's out. Damn. Niggas make niggas dance for no reason at that motherfucker.
The sun's out.
Nah, but I fuck with you, Illa. I'm just playing, kid. Don't take that to the heart. But still, pump right,
on
for
the
sure.
Flip side, though, yeah. Why we ain't invited over here? Nobody.
Everybody
this
invited.
First time is hot.
I feel like everybody invited. Everybody talk about being invited, but nobody
crowded
up
over here sometimes.
So all right, let's talk about it. Let's talk about it, right?
They be crowded over here sometimes.
When they come through, they gonna want to be mic'd up. That's three, right?
Uh-huh. Or they can come one by one.
No, that was if either. But
that's
I'm saying
the only
we not
way, really.
We not gonna be able to see nobody. Like when we gonna be able to? It's not gonna be dope.
They well, got we, one
this,
by
this,
one.
This is it will be dope because this is what we do over here.
We never had a lot of people mic'd up and like niggas be scattered around. Like this is probably
what I'm saying, it can be one by one though, right?
That's easy.
Yeah, but that's of course. We went over there one by one.
But I'm just yeah, but I thought they was talking as a whole. But no, if they I don't think they'd pull up like Dolly and shit. Nah, nigga Spooky
sure.
J, huh?
For sure they
yeah, that's
what dance!
That's what it all
that's what they saying. They saying we need some ladies over here. They saying like nah y'all need to do we need some ladies over here. But that's I don't think they mean they all gotta come together.
Okay, bet. We could bring whoever through that wanna slide.
But that's the thing, though.
Worm,
everybody
right here.
Yeah, we can put Worm up in the loop. Yeah, Worm. That's mad space
up.
For Worm.
Barked
wait,
up.
You wait, Tyler. You said Worm had a stick, so she don't count.
I was off the Mr. Mushy yesterday, man. Hey, man what
okay.
I said that to her.
Yeah, you said that.
You believe that?
I'm just going off what you said.
You
I'm saying if, I'm just saying if that's the case, she don't count.
Get on this nigga Worm. He's trying to throw you in the paint.
Nah,
get on
I'm
this nigga Worm.
What you
it's
said.
Up now.
Hey, shout out to Worm.
Don't get nervous.
I ain't nervous. Right. Shout out to Worm.
Stand on that.
But I'm just saying that's
you
what you. That was your narrative,
stand
though.
On that.
That was your narrative. You said that.
Hey, yo, Tiny is going crazy today, huh? Hey, what?
But she was part of over there too, so she gets some shots
like
for her
to
too.
Bombs up. You like to drop bombs? Up.
Nah, them these jabs.
I throw bows on them.
These jabs, these bombs.
Nah, yeah.
I'm about to say.
Yeah, man. Yeah, that's what I was gonna say, but I was just. Yeah, but that, shout out to the ladies' night though, man.
Yeah,
they most definitely
them.
Can slide. You know what
for
saying?
Sure. But that's what I was about to say.
Legit invites, then, man.
You invited them today. What happened?
This is true.
Yeah, what are you talking about?
Said, yeah,
this
you
is
told
true.
Him you said pull
this
up Saturday.
Is, yeah, this is true. This is true.
The invite was sent.
Baby, gotta treat them like a lady. Then go hit
them. I know how Palm be rocking. I'm just going from what I see. Huh?
Yeah.
I know how it go.
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying.
That's over there.
That's all I'm saying. What? That's all I'm saying. What?
Comfortable in that environment.
Yeah, man.
Mark was just dancing around the whole building. Shirt
on. Yeah, man. I already see. Like, just imagine, though, like, we have had ladies' night over here, and niggas start pulling their nipples out.
Okay, dog.
That's not a safe space. Like, you know what I'm saying? Ah, dance! Like, niggas thought that was. You feel what I'm saying? Don't keep, like. Like, I don't think that's what, you feel me? Hey, Pun, I know you in the chat. All right, I heard. Free them. Free ladies night.
Free ladies night.
Oh,
man.
Shit.
Free ladies night, man.
Oh, shit.
Pull up. Yeah, I invited y'all for today. That's crazy. Nobody hit me up.
You did.
Up.
That's what I'm saying. You
that's
sent
crazy.
The invite out.
Yeah,
the invite was sent. It was sent. Wow.
That shit got rejected.
It got rejected,
no,
man.
No. It didn't get rejected. Well, it did get rejected, Pun, but it got rejected.
That motherfucker.
That's what I'm saying. Ah! He intercepted that motherfucker. Y'all think y'all going where?
You gonna do what?
Dance!
Yeah! Oh yeah. My God! Oh shit! Just imagine though. That's crazy.
Damn.
Free ladies night.
I know.
How did you put that on the thing?
What?
For that?
Yeah, dance. Yeah, that's gonna be the new shit. I'm gonna tap through that one. Hey, Ace Boy Yummy Bear sent who said, "Hey, what color was the wig you used to wear, King?"
Granny had flavors. Shit, so you know what I mean? The golden browns, the lavendors.
Your sexy had, red edition?
No, I never had sexy red.
What about the one like Illa? I mean, not Illa. What's her name yesterday? Worm. The
dark brown ones. What, Worm?
The Worm wig.
George Washington?
No.
Did you see that picture? So. Did you see that
Granny
picture?
Granny didn't really like them gray ones. Not they didn't really like them gray ones like that.
Bruh, I seen this picture of Worm floating around like, looking like one of the judges and shit.
Oh, from yeah, out the UK. Like Dollar Bill.
Right. Yeah. I don't know who made that shit. Like a Dollar Bill is hilarious here. Dog, I don't know if you niggas seen that shit. Did I? Look at this shit. You haven't seen this?
Floating around, yeah.
Bruh.
I seen that floating around.
The internet.
I ain't like that shit when I left them niggas.
You know, see?
Well, they house, not them niggas.
Oh,
when
yeah.
I left they house.
She look like she should be on Mount Rushmore.
Bruh. She definitely look like Mount Rushmore, bruh. Hey, chat. Why did Cryptic do this? That nigga lost his mind, homie. Wormy Washington is crazy funny. Hey, Pun, I see you, my boy. We heard. We heard, man. We got the memo. And we heard about what's going on, man. We seen what you doing over there with Ladies Night and how they we know why they trying to get away.
Pun in the chat. Hey, let's address your race too since you here,
yeah,
nigga.
He definitely is in the chat.
Let's address that race first off.
Wobble whoopee, baby. Wobble wobble. Wobble, baby.
Hey, first off though, why are y'all racing on the sidewalk? Real niggas that's gonna race gonna get in the street and race. These two big ass niggas hugging each other on the sidewalk. Are you march? Get set. Why are y'all racing on the sidewalk? So both of y'all in violation. Throw the flag on the play. It's over for y'all. Pun, you got 5 steps and you stop, my nigga.
Yeah, the Olympics. Niggas need to push the Olympics back.
Yeah, come on, man. 5 steps, kid.
Push it back for what? For what?
Cause them niggas.
Pun ran 5 steps. Did you see the race?
No, I didn't.
These niggas did a 10-yard dash, and Pun ran 2 yards. And
was it fast though?
Pun, you got the race?
That nigga.
Do I got it?
Yeah.
I'm probably on one of these niggas. Let me go.
Pun race up, man. I like that thumbnail. They dropped the cold thumbnail on me today and shit.
Who?
Shout out to the Ace Boys, man.
Oh, they cooking my boy King.
Cooked me up today, man.
Oh my God.
Fuck with. That's crazy. On my page, I ain't even got to get to the thumbnails and all that shit yet. They done dressed me up about like 4 times on that motherfucker.
Oh, yeah. Niggas got some cold pain to you, my nigga.
Who they have, yeah? Mrs. Doubtfire?
Nah, they got me a cold motherfucker, homie.
Tiny making that. He just said Mrs. Doubtfire.
I see it. I'm thinking.
They got me on a cold.
I can't find it. Look for that motherfucker. That motherfucker, I can't. I don't know where that shit at.
Yeah. But yeah, Pun, you gotta get it together, my nigga. You got like
who
you
is
said,
racing?
AD. 10-yard dash.
We're gonna take that nigga to the old people's home, convalescence, and let him, you know what I'm saying, get off a couple of Olympic races up there.
That nigga put his hat to the back like he was about to
get off on some shit. Hey, chat, where that video at? Hey, y'all smash the like button and all that shit, too.
That nigga put his hand to the back like he was about to get off, man.
You know what I be thinking
thought
about?
Like he was going to have some aerodynamics. Like aerodynamics was going to matter.
Hey, you better be lucky a chihuahua wasn't after your ass.
Saying, what are you doing with a dog? When a dog, like a cold one, get up out.
He going to have to kick it.
Nah, you going to have to jump up. You going to have to run up the car.
Bruh, nah, it wasn't. He was done. His energy. He left the stream after he did that little two race.
Ooh, I got to get up out of here, boy.
So.
He was done.
That nigga went to the ER.
Stick a fork in him. Nigga went and got one of them IVs.
I was pushing that life alert button over there. Like.
Nigga went and got one of them IVs.
Damn, bud. That's really Red funny to Fox me, girl.
That nigga
Groove, he left the street.
He left that stream and went to his studio. Dance!
Do something to make me feel good. Yeah.
Pun mad.
Do something to make me feel better.
Yeah, do something to make me feel better. Hey, you really are. What was that nigga name? Aaron.
St. Louis.
St. Louis.
That nigga name was St. Louis? I thought the dude name was on Money Talk.
That was the nigga that was in the wheelchair.
Backseat. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I know exactly. No, that's the nigga from, what's that shit? What's that Players Club?
Yeah.
Do something to make me feel better. Yeah, that's some funny ass shit, man.
Yeah, next time get in the street though, Pun. Stop racing on the sidewalk, my nigga.
What you got for Pun out there?
Huh?
What you got for Pun out there if y'all was to race? After seeing that, from what you just said.
He could go half the distance. He could go half the distance. I still beat that nigga.
At least he got out there though. You didn't get out there and race with me though.
I stood up and walked out.
Why y'all didn't rush?
I stood up and said, let's go. Y'all talking about, wait.
Y'all, we can go right now. I'll go record with y'all right now.
Come on.
You want to go right now?
Yeah.
Nah, for real. I would do it, though, but I'm just letting you know.
I would do it, too.
You sure you can?
If that's what it is, it's going to be what it is.
Are you sure, though? Because I don't want you putting no hamstrings out there.
Oh, that is true, but I'll do it for the content.
All right.
I'll do it for the content.
We'll do it then. I'm with it.
All right.
So, wait, this for the content or is this for the sport?
I'll beat him personally, but I'll definitely do it for the content.
It's
for both. It's for the sport.
Every time I be beating niggas, I'll be on the camera
content.
Anyway.
It's for the sport of content. It's crazy.
For the sport of content.
y'all gonna do it for real or what?
When you trying to do it?
We'll do it at the show.
Alright.
What's up, my nigga? A-Cuss in 199.
Start stretching now.
Terrell had Rory on Shame on You, but won't guidance from JB. Yeah, man, he won't guidance. Lord A sent five. Man, fuck all that. That long explanations from King Bulldog face ass. Get to the witch story. Yeah, we're gonna get to that witch story. Hold on real quick. Peter Brooks in 99 and said, what would make BET relevant again? BET is relevant, man. Just the way we used to consume BET ain't the same, man.
Shout out to Peter, man.
That's the same nigga?
Yeah, man, that's all I was just telling you about. Shout out to Peter, man.
Okay, shout out Peter Brook.
Yeah,
but yeah, what would make BET relevant again? I think, yeah, the way we used to consume BET just wasn't, it's not the same, first off. It's just like we used to watch that shit on TV originally. You get what I'm saying tonight? Like, a lot of niggas not on watching TV, so I feel if they was able to serve the streaming platforms the way they did that, then they can figure that shit out.
I think they gotta come with a cold ass show.
Definitely a cold show. That's like, we gotta really get some to. Music shows will make BET relevant.
Yeah.
Music shows.
They might need the Apollo.
Yeah,
definitely.
They gotta
Apollo. Yeah.
Apollo, that's a good start.
That's definitely fire.
Apollo for BET.
Yeah.
Apollo for BET.
Shout out
to AD. I seen that on
Patreon.
They said on two another one, but I heard it on the Joe Budden one.
Yeah, for sure. Me too. Shout out to AD. AD always saying he always include Apollo when he say his shit though. I remember AD saying that. He like always include Apollo. He definitely let the record reflect right there. Shout out to
my nigga AD, man. AD. He a solid nigga for shit show, bro.
But AD, he said he'll vote me off if we was in motherfucking
Big Brother House. Shout out shit over with. Look at that nigga.
I got watch good now. He ain't trying to vote me out. Big Brother House. You ain't never seen Big Brother House?
No, what's that?
It's like basically Kid came up with an idea where all the people under their umbrella just stay in the house.
Oh, okay.
And then everybody, you gotta vote niggas out.
Like Real World?
Yeah. I guess, yeah. But Real World was what, MTV?
Yeah.
Yeah, Big Brother like TV. CBS.
Yeah, that's what BET need. BET need the messy show.
So in that case right there, right, we all go in there.
Probably just more like.
So let me ask y'all feel like we supposed to go in there and we supposed to be politic against everybody else first?
What you mean?
Yeah.
Of course.
But you already see like you, they easy to persuade you and shit. So
I'm pretty much a, I like mom.
character, man.
So, I love us.
Why though? Yeah, I love us. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm talking about all of us, isn't
it? Because it's strength in numbers.
It's strength in numbers.
Because when it boiled down, because
look, looking out for yourself.
No, no.
You plan on getting me out the way, right?
If we plan and it start boiling down and it's all four of us left,
then what's going on?
Then ATF 50.
What you talking about?
I'm saying if it was just us four left in the house, we go 50s.
That's gonna be your companion.
Nah, that ain't gonna be my companion.
Cold. That's a cold
word. Well, we gonna get y'all to pay.
It can start off.
But I'm saying no, because when if it boiled down and it's you left and all of the Ace boys, they gonna get rid of you easy.
It don't matter if the name of the game is if it's supposed to be me at the end anyways. What does it matter? That's cap then.
It's not cap. You ain't never watched the show Survivor.
Let's go take them boys out.
You ain't never watched the show Survivor.
So basically,
you really going in as a free agent?
I can.
That's you crazy.
Are, you already going in against the Apollo.
Who?
You?
How?
50s.
Nah, I'm saying if it was just us four left.
That's already so. You already got your. I never thought that far ahead.
This right now, early. You know, in the house, I'm like, my nigga Mac.
Nah,
you
see, first bump in the street.
That's how the game go.
That's your strategy. Already backdoored them. Shout out to the congregation. All right, so listen, 50.
That's because he want to keep letting that narrative go. So that's all. Hey, Shay. If whatever the case is, and it boiled down, and we the last four, I feel like we won. Even though we'll have to still survival the fittest, and we all still have to try to do our shit to win.
So which means, as soon as the game start,
I'm with y'all.
I'm eligible to get you out right now.
Duh, that's how it go. You ain't never watched Survivor.
You'd be mad at me though if I did that.
Yeah, stupid.
That's crazy.
Why would I be? Why wouldn't I be mad?
Why would you be mad?
In that shit, you gotta build fake alliances with that shit too.
Yeah,
it's all true.
So basically, we it's already
you gotta yeah, build
we
fake
already the fake alliance.
Who?
Damn. Us.
No.
50s.
No, we the Avengers.
Yeah. That ain't what Tiny said.
I said, well, it's all four. But then that's what I'm pushing him. That's that. And then I'm going to come to you, my nigga Mag. Put me on the street world. Hey.
Oh, Tiny coming in already pushing. He already.
Hey, man, we gotta get these niggas up out of here.
Why that nigga sound like Casper though?
Man, put me in the streaming world.
You're trying to sound creepy with it.
Nah, man.
That's how bad the cap is.
Bruh, that's how the game go. Y'all ain't never. So how was you just going in as just free agent?
Yes.
That's crazy. See, we lost already. It ain't gonna be us, folks.
Was a we though. That's basically what Kill said.
Oh, right. It's a way to me.
You want
to
lie all the way so you can get it.
I say when it's
the end. You want to what? Look me in my eyes and say,
I got you, bitch.
Ken, no, I feel like being a free agent.
Huh?
That's what you gonna be doing at the end by yourself.
So if bruh, it, let's just say hypothetically
you don't get the concept of the whole shit. Bruh.
No, all right. So hypothetically speaking, so when it get down to just you and 50s, what's gonna happen?
Y'all supposed to vote. The people that everybody else voted out, y'all vote, and who went out of us too.
Oh, it's a voting game. I never watched.
So
that
that's
shit.
When that that's when them alliances come in because niggas like, gonna be like,
that's my brother.
That nigga kept it clean, and that's this it. Nigga voted us out.
Yeah.
So we gonna run with this nigga.
So if I come in as free agent, I'm keeping it the cleanest off the rip.
No,
y'all
you're not.
Do what y'all gotta do. Y'all about to get me out of here?
Yep. If you ain't got no alliance, you getting up out of here.
Oh, that sounds tight right there. I want to play that game right there.
Yeah, y'all ain't never watched Survivor, cuz?
No, I ain't never watched that shit.
All right. One of my teachers was on there.
What's Survivor?
But they in the woods and shit.
What they in the woods?
Yeah.
In the jungle for a month.
Doing
but it's still the same concept. Like you vote niggas.
You gotta survive.
You gotta survive. Yeah.
Survive what?
Nigga, the jungle.
The jungle. You gotta
survive. You go up in the jungle just like Tarzan?
Yeah, you ain't eating.
Nah, not Tarzan. You gotta wash your clothes
in the water.
You do like little.
In the lakes and shit.
You do little events and shit for like food. The winner get food, peanut butter and jelly. The loser food, just go. Yeah.
Okay.
Y'all gonna win this.
But that's out there in like the wild though.
Sleep they ain't under a no leaf goddamn in a thunderstorm.
They setting up all the animals. They setting up all the bites, man.
Oh yeah. I believe that too.
Gilligan's Island, man.
I believe that.
Nah, shout out, man. Shout out, bro, for shit show.
Hey, y'all niggas ever went camping?
Yeah, I did.
I've been camping.
I never been camping.
What you had in your kit?
I had no kit. What you mean?
I'm saying with like you, with your tent. Like, what'd you bring with you? Man. Like,
oh,
I
shit.
I didn't think I went with a tent.
You niggas just went.
I took a nigga tent. Nigga.
Oh, I'm gonna just sleep in this motherfucker.
I took a tent. I swear to God.
Where was that though? Like, that shit was like.
I don't remember. I was a kid. We went with Lutish Park, man. They just did take all the kids out together of camping and shit.
Yeah, that's what
I was. Oh, so y'all was just out there with blankets and shit?
Nah, niggas had tents. I was just a nigga that knew I was gonna take a nigga. Tent when I get outside.
So y'all was sharing the tent?
I took the tent.
Oh, you took the nigga whole thing?
Yeah. We had to go bunk up one of his partners. M's in the chat.
Everything's coming.
You said you took the whole tent by yourself?
Yeah.
You was in the tent with him? Eventually, because all the tents is two people.
What are you talking about?
When you went to camp.
That's the camp you went with.
I went to the Lutish Park one.
No, you didn't go to the one I went. I didn't go to that one. I never seen you.
No, I never seen you. So I'm asking, what kind of camp was it?
I'm saying.
You said y'all had your own tents?
I said I didn't have a tent. I took a tent from somebody.
But you was assigned to a tent, right? With somebody.
No, why are you so lost? Obviously, that's your rules. So I got to get to your rules.
So over there, they didn't have a tent for you and your partner?
You bring your own tent. You so lost.
Oh, you bring your own tent?
Yes. I didn't come with a tent. So obviously you were sharing tents with niggas.
They definitely wasn't making niggas bring their own tents on me in camping trips, though. That's just what
I never been in no camping trip.
I don't know about camping trip.
Hey, in the chat, they was not making the kids in the ghetto bring their own tents.
How old was y'all?
I think I was like, I don't know, 10.
Yeah, I don't know. I was in middle school.
Middle school.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what Kim's situation was. I don't know Kim's situation. That was like, I don't know. You feel me? You was bunked up with niggas in the tent. That wasn't how our situation was.
Yeah, so you just didn't bring a tent. You just knew I'm going to take me a nigga tent when I get up there.
100%. 100%. Actually, 200%. Yeah, that's how I went, though.
These niggas are actually 200%.
Yeah, I for sure knew I was taking one of them niggas' tents.
Oh, shit.
But who you knew at the park?
At the park?
Yeah, like, what was the... Who took y'all?
What you mean? I used to get picked up over there. That's where the pickup was, drop off and shit.
It definitely was, though.
Yeah, right there, right in front of that white church back there. There was a church or something right there on that back street.
Yeah, that was two different events then. We wasn't. Yeah, yours was the shared tent one. I don't know about that one, bruh.
The shared tent one.
Yeah, we didn't get picked up right there, though, but we was on bullets, but. This y'all, I don't even know what parky, what church you talking about.
I don't think it's a church. Something right there.
What church you talking about?
The white church that used to have a barbecue?
Church?
What church? You still have a barbecue in front of that motherfucker?
No. There's a white building over there, dog. It's like a white building. It looked like it's important. Something right there, right behind the back of that park. It's just a street. And it looked like it's important. I forget what it is, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. All
right.
Yeah. Behind the park.
Yeah. For sure. Yeah. Shout out my brother. my nigga Johnson J. Lewis in 499. Keem Wright. It's entitlement that advises in that advice is a consultation fee if there is no relationship. I mean, I feel that too, though.
Consultation fee, they just what? Holla at a nigga.
Yeah. What's that like? I guess.
You know, you just charging for the game.
Damn, what they say, the game is to be sold and not told.
It's not. Who is they?
I'm saying, like, that's like, I've heard that phrase before.
Yeah, that's that's classic.
Yeah.
So, let's talk about my nigga Bell and these witches then, huh? What's that about? Ooh. Is it any truth to those details? Smash a like button.
Yeah, man. We went to a show. We had a show in Oregon, right? So we pull up to the shit. We get there, right? We get there like it's like pregame. You feel me? We didn't fly there. You feel me? We hit the road. You know, packed up all our bags, hit the road. It's like what, a day, 18 hours.
18 hours.
You feel me? So we get there. It's like it's almost close to showtime. We get there and it's basically almost close to showtime. But you know. The nigga that's kind of putting together the show, one of the niggas that put together the show, he like, yeah, man, come to our little space. We got a little space. We want to show you it's going to be where the after party at. I mean, y'all been to tours before. You know y'all go through logistics, meet people and shit. So we go down there. We get down there. Two females walk down there. I'm talking about they was fine.
What ethnicity was that?
They was white. I ain't gonna lie.
Why you say it like that?
Cause you know people don't be fucking with the swine like that.
With the swine? Wait a minute. What you mean the swine? You like pork? Like pork? What's this thing?
No, like white women.
Why you say swine?
I don't know. That's the homie hit me with that one time. A long time ago.
Oh shit!
Like, I'm like, what does that mean? But like, you know, so it's white.
Saying the swine. You seen the swine and then what?
Nah, so but they look like volleyball players. Like, you know, they like 5'8", 5'9".
Oh, the good swine.
I'm talking about, yeah. And the one that you get on them up and be popping. Pop, pop, pop. Come on. this Trader Joe's swine.
Oh yeah, yeah,
oh,
yeah.
God. So I'm like, what's up with them? I tell TF, you fuck up, like, what's up with them? He looked. And this, mind you, this is at the era where this nigga be playing a lot. Like, you know, I remember one time this nigga was like, yeah, I got an interview for my new Under Armour shoe. Come watch, tap in and watch it. You know, this nigga used to be playing a lot.
Oh, bro, that's when I set up that commercial for Smack when that nigga was working out in the drawers.
Yeah, you did do that.
Yeah, this nigga, this nigga wore the drawers like it was a whole
dance.
Like a leotard.
He did do that, though.
Bro, that's, I got to find that footage, man, because he recorded it. Like,
do you smack? What the rock is cooking?
Shout out Smack, man.
Hey, no, back funny right now.
Smack been trying to do content forever.
Don't let me hang it. That was funny.
That was a good one. I think they catched that one.
But yeah. So alright, so then what happened? So you went to TF and said call. What's up with
you? I tapped them. It was two of them. It was like they was legit. I tapped them. I'm like, what's up with them? You see them? Like, you feel me on something? This is my first time touring. You feel me? This is my first time like being a rapper out the stage. You feel me? I'm with my boy, they, you know, I'm about to
first
open up.
Stop.
It's my first stop.
Fat pack of swine.
Yeah.
Fresh pack of swine. So, last party, boys.
I don't mean to be, you know, disrespectful or call a swine. That was like,
that's a joke. It's all, yeah. It's good. It's good.
So he like he look at him. He like, nah, they make the ones. I'm like, what you talking about?
Oh, he already see.
You know, he's like,
he was impapped up.
He was like, you see that tattoo? I'm like, I look. I'm like, yeah, they both had a tattoo.
What was the tattoo?
It's a triangle with a tree in it. Like on some cold shit, low key. Now they're like, you know, hindsight is 20/20. So I'm like, man, this nigga fucking playing around.
You said
man.
It was some what shit though?
Huh?
What kind of tattoo? What was the meaning of it if you knew?
I don't know. It was like a triangle with a tree in it.
Okay.
But like some like.
What that means, yeah? You know? Are you able to talk about that shit?
I don't know, but I kind of figured what it looked like, some shit I seen before.
But like, it was like some other shit around it. I'm thinking like,
and they both had the same. That's the only thing.
But I'm like, bro, they both had the same thing. They from the middle of nowhere. They probably just getting shit done.
Nah, that shit it was a little too deep.
Okay. Yeah.
Do you recognize any of these?
Nah, come on.
Glasses
thing. This nigga crazy. You recognize him? <it?
laughs> Hey, this nigga funny as fuck.
You know, I be watching it. I be heavy on the movie type shit. You feel me?
I don't want to look at it.
No, I don't want to say it was any one of them, but it definitely was. That's what it was. And she had some other shit around me. And I'm like, all right, whatever. But I'm thinking this nigga playing. Like, this nigga, he just talking shit. He about to perform, you know, whatever. So. Whatever go on, they show my little, they show documentary. I had a documentary out of the time, 28 shots. So then they all like watching. It's like
wait. How did you You with them now?
Yeah, no.
They came to the show.
The show before.
Oh, that was going to the show originally.
Yeah. Everybody going to the show. It was nothing
cracking out there. So we was like,
yeah, it's cracking. What we doing? Like we are the event.
Look at him. I am talent.
Yeah. Nah, so it's like that's what's going on out there. And so shit before the show, before I went on stage, they showed a documentary, you feel me, just to like kill time. But when they watch it, it's like this, it's quiet in there. I'm like, like, yeah, they really fuck with it. So I go out.
They fucking with me out there,
yeah,
y'all.
They feel that.
Yeah, they feeling this. It's an inspiration, motivational shit. You know, that be my whole angle. You feel me? So it's like, I'm like, they fucking with it. So then I go out there, I do my shit. It's like three people. It's like three women in the front. They're like going crazy. They going crazy. They turning up. And then, you know, I leave. I'm like, yeah, I did that shit. I went crazy. TF looking like, yeah, you did good. But he like, he looking, you know, this the whole time now, like now even like replaying in my mind, like his whole energy was kind of like peeping shit. It wasn't just like excitement, like to be out here. I don't know. But me, I'm looking at it like this nigga just did 30 tours. You feel me? This is probably just another stopper, bro. But the whole time, he probably was just peeping the scene. I'm not even really knowing. So he like, hey, you gonna, for my set, I'm gonna let you come out and do two more songs. I'm like, oh yeah, that's a real nigga, you feel me? So I got out there. So when it's his time to do the set, now the girls that's in the front, they like, yeah, yeah, yeah. Am I lying?
Nah, TF said that part.
What's that though?
I don't know what it is, but that's what they doing.
TF said
throwing stuff at you.
They not throwing nothing. Ain't nothing being thrown.
Oh, they just in the crowd.
Yeah.
And they yelling out, yeah, too.
Yeah. I'm like, yeah.
Real shit. And they was in sync. Like, they was in sync.
But I'm turned up. I'm like, nigga, I'm out here.
He's standing right in front of the bit. Like, they like right here.
When he stepped back. And then when he stepped back, I'm like, what are you doing? Like, you supposed to be up here turned up. I'm like, what's mad? So then, like, she even passed me a little weed. Hit the weed, I didn't even know what it was, but I'm so turned up. So then, like, boom, that happened. Then after the show, we kind of go to, like, the green room. We was about to turn the nigga to Zakari. This nigga put out a knife on the nigga and some more shit. Did the whole little
You ever forgot about that.
Nigga flipped the knife, put the knife on the table, point in.
Yeah, this nigga came back there playing, I had a knife. Nigga twisted the knife in the fingers and shit, stabbed that shit in the table, nigga. That nigga
like,
was like,
I don't fuck around like Steven Seagal.
Nah, real shit. That nigga kept like, coming so back.
Y'all niggas
playing.
Is out here trying to impress the hoes.
Nah, it's not hoes. This some weird nigga. Like, it was like some weird shit that happened. Like, we was about to turn the nigga to Zakari.
Nah, we did. We booked him for his little half of something.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, we took some bud.
Yeah, but we made him get up out of there.
Yeah, running his wheel though. He was gonna take his wheel.
They
like, nah, he like, nah, we not out here for like that. If anything, we whoop his feet. So that happened. So then we get back, turned up. Niggas like, the niggas come like, hey man, we have an after party. Come visit. I mean, come to the spot. You feel me? It's gonna be lit. It's like, okay, what else we gonna do? Of course we're gonna have an after party. I get down there. You feel me? I'm down there. I'm popping my shit. Niggas loaded. Niggas drinking and shit. You know, I go. Niggas seen the little chick. I'm like, what's up? What's going on? I'm like, she like, you know, she giving me that energy like it's green, as a man. So
it's green, what?
As a man.
As a man, it's green.
You feel me? She like, you feel me? She giving me that energy like it's going down. I'm like, shit, for sure. So I tell this nigga, yeah, if he like, I'm like, bro, what you talk about? You about to go? I'm like, man, I'm about to leave. I'm about to do my thing. He said, bro, you know where we at? I'm like, shit, nigga, we in Oregon. He said, exactly. You sure you want to go do that? I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna be good, man. I got protection, whatever, yada yada. So I sent him. I'm like, I'm gonna send you my location. So I sent him the location. He's spitting off, mind you. They don't have no Ubers out there. They just got all shuttle buses. You feel me? So it's no Uber where we at. It's not like, nigga, if anything was to happen, nobody could log on the app and be like, oh, this is where he was his last place at. You feel me? It's just all shuttle buses. So even like the Uber driver talking like, oh, we going like a little, this is kind of a little outskirts aside of town. But it's like only like 5 minutes away. But like where the town is, it's like.
It was a long 5 minutes.
Yeah, it's like,
it was like 15 minutes, so, 5 minutes.
You know, like if you in the trees, if you in the woods, 5 minutes seem like a long time.
Cause everything looked the same.
You can't see nothing, everything looked the same. So he's like, damn, y'all going a little outskirts, you know me? I'm like, yeah, okay. I'm like, I ain't tripping, I'm just trying to go do my thing. So we pull up to this old looking house, like this motherfucker look crazy. And it's a gang of like trees and woods in front of them, trees and motherfucking. Like, I'm like, this shit look like some American Horror Story type shit, fake for real. But I'm like,
fake for real. I love that nigga.
So I'm like, all right, I'm like, but whatever. I'm like, you know, in the back of my mind, nigga, this is gonna be one of my tour stories. Like, you feel me? I'm up, you feel me? Yeah. So then go in there, I get in there. She passed me like a drink. I know after the thing I said it was a goblin, but you know. So she passed me a drink. It smelled kind of funny, but I'm like, fuck it, I'm gonna love it anyway.
That nigga, Edgy passed me a drink. Yeah, so, it smelled kind of funny, but I'm trying to fuck something anyway.
Exactly. So,
she gave that nigga a roofie.
Yeah, that so nigga a roofie.
I'm like, when I went up to bed, like, I drank it, and, like, you know, a little time went past. I'll probably say, like, a minute and a half, almost 2 minutes. Then I just start hearing noises, like, people humming. Like, but I'm thinking she got like a retarded like not retarded. I think it's not like that. I'm saying she, I think that she got like a roommate, whatever going on. So they back there doing some weird shit. Or again, you don't know people might have fetishes and whatever. So
I just think you in there, you the nigga in that motherfucker. Yeah. Bitches so in like, there fetished up.
Yeah. So I was like, and then I'm like, what the fuck? The sound getting louder then two like four people walk out with cloaks and shit. And I'm like, what the fuck going on in here? So she's like, you want to come to my room? Still, you know.
He's still trying to bomb. Niggas in there with cloaks on and all that.
So then I'm like, we get to the top of the stairs, the shit get louder. And I'm like, I don't know, man. I start, you know, my empath start kicking in. I'm like, man, I don't feel right. Like, something, yeah. I gotta go.
Yeah.
So nigga, I'm like, man, I'm leaving. So I run downstairs. You feel me? I'm trying to open up the door. It's shaking, it's doing that. You don't know, nigga, fucking, heart racing at this point, nigga. Like, nigga, the sound's getting louder, the hum's getting louder, nigga. As I'm trying to open up the door, take it out, nigga. I'm running. I just started, nigga. I'm running. I text TF like, man, I'm leaving. I'm running.
Was you screaming?
No. I'm running. Nigga, I'm running fast. You feel me? I'm like running.
These bitches is after me.
No, I text TF when I say I'm about to leave. I say, bro, come get me ASAP before I run downstairs. Open the door. I'm running. All I see, nigga, is the lights. Hit the shit. They made a right. I jumped in the car. And then, nigga, that's all I remember. Then this nigga said, no, that bitch was, I mean, she was floating. So I'm like, yeah, it was definitely some real shit going on. And I'm like, yeah, then she was a witch. Like, I'm like, it was definitely some creepy going on in there.
You don't, what, like,
I have
so many signs not to go with them.
But I'm saying, this is my first time being in this environment, like, on tour. Like, I ain't never really been out of California.
There's no other bitches there.
Was it any other bitches there?
Them the bitches that was fucking with me.
Them the bitches that was fucking with me.
You what you say? Like,
I'm saying, just the house, nothing like that. You said, I'm with this shit. I'm like,
that was giving me the energy. What I supposed to do? Like, you know what? I'm like,
I mean, UNTF's story is similar though, because I remember the story that TF said on here, and you kind of pretty much said what he said.
I see. The thing is, I don't know that side of the story.
Yeah, you didn't know the inside of the house.
I was stripping out. I quit rapping.
Yeah, a nigga quit rapping. He's like, TF, nigga, if I wasn't rapping, you wouldn't even bring me here. Nigga.
I'm like, bro,
nigga,
is this the tour of life? This would like, come with him, nigga.
I don't know what this nigga seen, but whatever it was, that nigga was like,
all cloaked up, bro.
That was the energy.
That didn't matter to you, though. You were still trying to go in the room, though.
You was trying to, like, you was looking for your cloak.
But I got to the top of the stairs, and I'm like, nah, I got to leave, because the nigga, the sound started getting louder. Then they started, like, lining up. I'm like, what's going on?
You needed you a cloak. That's all you needed. If they would have handed you a cloak, you would have gotten that line.
Nah, man.
And then yeah, like, Shaquille Sunflower.
That's about the cloak.
Boy,
and he was like, she was floating, and I'm like, bro,
this was floating.
He
like,
said she was floating. I couldn't even see nothing because I was running.
It looked like she was on a hoverboard. Her feet wasn't doing none of this shit. Nigga, she was just like,
come
like,
here,
real shit. At a high speed, though. Bad.
Y'all don't listen.
Cause this nigga fast.
Yeah, all right, so boom. So you on the main road now?
Nah, it was in the forest. It was in the forest.
Yeah.
So TF, he just come through. He get the drop. He already got the thing, so. He just, bust this right
MacGyver,
here.
No, I had the location.
TF pull up MacGyver already. He just instantly MacGyver.
Jay was already in the car because he wasn't feeling well.
Yeah.
So we was already like,
niggas was,
Jay was already telling like, bro, I'm sick. I'm not, he drove 18 hours to get there. He's not even trying to party no more.
Yeah.
We sat in the back the whole time. Nigga, we trying to, well, at least me, he wasn't really on that. He was already like, nigga, he was on some like, nigga, we doing here, we leaving. Me, I'm like, I'm young. I'm like, I'm trying to go.
trying to go move around.
Yeah, no, I'm just trying to see like how theatrical was it though. So, boom, you doing the door and shit.
Yeah, bro.
Like, right, so boom.
I feel like low-key, I feel like one of them grabbed my shirt at you.
See?
One of those.
So that's what I think, that's why I think you bullshit with the
stuff. Yeah, because you said if they would have happened, they would have happened. What if they was intermediate?
Like, how they, okay, I get what you're saying. Like, how they just let him leave.
Yeah, how they let you leave and you just get to bounce out the...
They probably,
all the way up the stairs.
They probably wanted that nigga to, that drink to kick in so he could just pass out. They didn't want no fight. Because you know it's different when, like, let's just say you get a fresh kill on a deer, right?
Like what you did one of those, of course.
Nah, I fuck with the animals heavy. But you know, if you get a fresh kill,
you fuck with animals heavy.
Yeah.
Why you not go vegan then,
nigga? Because why?
Because you fuck with animals heavy.
That's cold. That's
that is kind of deep. But I ain't never smoked no animal.
But so, you eat smoked animals, but for y'all.
Yeah, because you. Okay, I'm gonna get to that after this.
Okay,
I'm gonna get to that after this because you know my whole culture is that. You feel me? They like you after you get a good kill, you gotta thank the people and all that. And then you eat then you continue like because that's the cycle of life. But anyway, you get a fresh kill or a new kill. You know, like if a deer is scared when it die, the blood is bad. You know what I'm saying?
It's traumatized.
So they wanted him not to be scared. All that panic and shit. They didn't want that.
Nah, for sure. Yeah, they thought he was with getting close. Like, oh, you with all the shit. Like, okay. You know. You know what I'm saying?
But I'm telling you what.
I get it.
We'll give you something better than pussy.
You gonna get the cloak.
You getting the cloak, nigga.
I don't know. But when hindsight is 2020, so you start putting little bits of shit pieces in your like together, like damn, what the fuck happened? And then even like when I said like when they was watching this shit, it was just like it was dead silence in there. Like you can hear a pin drop. I'm talking about we had this event where people talk usually shit, you can hear a pin drop in there. And then as soon as I got on stage, nigga, they just start chanting.
Oh, so they felt like you had the opposite of what the deer's blood is. That's the story.
Yeah.
They're like, dang.
I mean, I don't know. That could be that. I mean, that could
they
be.
Like, this nigga got, about this, that. Nigga got
about the, like, probably,
this nigga got the blood we need. He's a survivor.
And probably the energy, too. You feel me? I don't know. But
all right, this is my last part, though. So, boom, you got the house. How far between the house? Like, you running through the woods now?
No.
You on your map?
I'm on the streets. I'm just running in the middle of the street. I'm trying to get away.
Damn, that's crazy, though.
I'm in the middle. Ask him. I'm running in the middle of the street.
But it's y'all's in the woods. Middle of the woods, okay?
No, yeah, it's like a dirt. It's a dirt road.
So, wait, Bell, you thought you was probably about to fuck something.
As a man.
As a man, obviously. So... Before you seen them cloaked up, you wasn't busting down or nothing.
Like, I didn't come off there with my shirt off. Like, yeah, it's party time.
Yeah. So, like, I'm trying to understand.
It's
like,
party time.
So, where you was at before you, like, you wasn't up in there?
I didn't even get the chance to go.
You didn't peel out or nothing?
Nah, it wasn't so. Even. I feel like if it got to that point, it would have been over with.
Oh, you would have fucked some creepy shit.
I mean, no, I think that
as a man. That's what I'm trying to see. If he ran out that crib like Tiny.
What if you would have really crashed that drink?
I didn't even drink it all. That's the thing. I was like, I'm good. Like, you feel me? Because we was already so drunk. Like,
well, yeah, that nigga was shady when he left.
Yeah, that's like, a ritual for sure, Kane.
Go ahead.
I was about to say, like, have you had, like, nightmares and shit after that? Or, like, what's up with that? No, now when I go places, I don't even fuck around. I went to a little spot in Texas. I'm just like, man, I'm cool. I'm just going to do the show. It's over. Except for... I did another show after that. It was kind of lit, but like
we went. That's crazy because we went back out there.
Oh, so then let me tell you the story. We went back. So we went back. I'm like, damn, fuck it. We gonna go back. They like, man, you gonna be cool. I'm like, man, I was low key scared.
That's crazy.
I'm like, man, hell no. F like, nah, nigga, you just don't be on that other shit. Just do what you're supposed to do and leave. I'm like, all right, for sure. So we get there. We go to this like little bakery in town. So it's me and this nigga sitting at the end of the shit. At the other end of the nigga, it's like a nigga that looked like fucking Raiden. You ever seen Mortal Kombat? Yeah. Nigga Raiden got the ponytail, gang of rings on. Right? I'm like, what the fuck? TF like, look at this nigga. So we talking. TF like, dude, that nigga might be like a warlock or something. I'm like, what the fuck? So we talking. So me and him like having a conversation like this. His phone right here, he looking for his phone. His phone way at the end of the table.
I'm like, what the fuck? He look up, the nigga, he in a chair that don't spin around. It's like a wooden, it's a wooden chair like this. And it's like this chair right here. It don't spin or nothing. Mm-hmm. So we look up, him in the chair turns around like this. We don't hear nothing. He just looking dead at us. He looking dead at me and him. Mm-hmm. He get his phone, we both turn our heads, he get his phone. We look back up, he not even there no more. Like, he disappeared.
Them niggas, he got sent in on us. Like, them niggas back.
Real shit.
Or he back.
In my cabin? Did that not happen?
No, nah, real shit.
So what y'all told, got? Y'all, what y'all do? Do y'all got rid of these niggas?
Huh?
Y'all get rid of these niggas or they still after y'all and shit? I don't popping
know.
Up and shit?
I don't know. We ain't been back there.
We ain't been back.
We ain't been back since.
They because know when also, you in town.
This was even
you
more.
You drunk the juice already. They know
this,
you in town.
This one was even more sick.
It's a tracker?
Yeah, it's a tracker for sure.
That's funny. He got that shit coursing through his veins. But look, the nigga who lined us up with the show, because he was still like that's our boy. We was like, bro, what's up with the bitches? Like, you knew them bitches was like that?
Yeah.
He like, yeah.
I'm about to put up the email, Harry.
You feel me? He like, yeah, like that's the whole thing out here.
Yeah. But when you think
I'm about to get one of them hoes.
The Blair Witch Project was shot in Oregon. The movie, like that.
That was a creepy movie, man.
You know what I'm saying?
You better than me, though.
And then if you look it up, it's like
I'm trying to figure out. I think you witches, were still witches, probably just tweaking.
A gang of witches died in Salem, Oregon. And like, if you look at which shit is like Salem, Oregon, that's like where they come from.
For real?
Yeah, that's like the hub of them.
Oh damn! So you was okay? Yeah. It's really the mix.
Yeah. Nah, that's really the tall thing.
It's all magic out there, then.
Yeah. That's why when I seen the text, I'm like, oh yeah.
So I feel like energy, even like that's why you got booked up, like because
we I don't here, see that email.
We been Harry. In Salem. What's it called?
Salem. It wasn't Salem.
No, nah, we wasn't in Salem.
You know, you heard about Salem and shit, right?
But I'm saying, I'm just saying, Oregon is like it just is a place. Salem is a small place.
Sabrina and all that shit.
But yes, Sabrina was in there. It's like it's where it's at when it comes to that.
Yeah. Okay, for sure. Yeah, y'all still ain't gonna get to that. How long was it from the house to?
Yeah, get to that part again.
Yeah. So I'm trying to figure out was he smashing down the road when they seen you high beams? Was it like the movies?
No, I'm saying it was like the movie. It was high beams.
So did you hear her running after you?
I didn't even hear her. I didn't know she was behind me until he said something.
So what, he out the window like?
No, he just opened. Nigga, I jumped in. And he opened up. It was the van. Pressed the van. I jumped in.
She floated past the window. While we was going this way, she kept going this way.
The homie, Tron was like, we should go out there and fight evil.
you remember Litron?
Yeah.
The dancing nigga?
Yeah.
He like, bro, let's go back. Let's go fight evil. I'm like, bro, the fuck are you? You ain't just see that bitch flying?
You didn't just see that bitch flying? It's crazy.
That's wild.
Yeah, Litron, my boy Reason popped him in the music video, Color Dreams, man.
Yeah, yeah, on the real with the work shirt on.
Yeah.
He popped him?
Yeah,
he did. He was there for that shit too.
But Jay was there, Jess was there, Masaki, Litron.
They all seen it?
Yes.
They saw the way.
They was driving. I wasn't driving.
Yeah, y'all know y'all real Scooby Doo crew though. I didn't know he was with them.
That's what I'm saying.
So I'm saying.
Scooby Doo crew.
That is definitely Scooby Doo.
Yeah, no, for sure. When he said Jay, I'm like, oh, okay, now it's making all the sense.
He the real man, Kyle.
Y'all niggas out there.
On the real, though. He's right. He's for sure. That nigga really had the mask.
Y'all was on the
shit. What's up, okay? He straight?
Yeah, that's small. All
right. Yeah.
I seen him straight.
Shout out to that nigga.
Shout out
to
that
nigga. Yeah, man, I'm trying to tell you, man.
Yeah, that was a cold. Yeah, niggas didn't sleep for 3 nights after that.
Nah, we stayed up the whole time. I know.
Cause we was still out there.
I was traumatic. I'm like, bro, I'm going to sleep. And I'm like, man, I ain't rapping no more. Fuck this. Then he woke up next day, gave me a little bit of show money. I'm like, yeah, I'm back in the game.
Yeah.
Yeah. He like, you last night. I'm like, damn, good looking. I'm back in the game.
Loaded past y'all. That's crazy, man.
Yeah, I didn't even see her. So is that like I wouldn't say religion, but is that like a
cult?
Like, yeah, like voodoo in the South? Is that would you equate that to the same thing? Or
I think when people say voodoo, I feel like voodoo is like that shit more intentional. Right? I think voodoo like
that shit sound intentional that they was trying to do to you?
Yeah, you're right.
So would you say it's the white voodoo?
It's magic? Witchcraft. Is voodoo witchcraft?
I don't know.
Voodoo.
Yeah, I think voodoo is voodoo. I don't think voodoo is witchcraft.
Voodoo, like
the drill music.
It's interesting.
It's music. Music is
real music.
Witchcraft, all that shit is. That's an interesting topic right there, though. But
drill music, witchcraft.
Yeah, the answer seems like no,
but it could be.
It's all.
Yeah. All this shit is. Music change your mood, like whatever you listen to could affect how
they
you
do that.
For sure.
Okay. Yeah, I ain't updated. I'm just trying to put two and two together.
And that's how. That's how people cast spells, words. So it's like.
Yeah. So do you say good morning or do you say grand rush?
Yeah, I say how you doing.
That's how you don't say good morning.
Nah, not really. I ain't say good morning in a long time.
I say top of the Lily.
Yeah.
Top of the Lee.
Top of the Leslie.
That's what I say, top.
What that mean?
Top of the Lily. Top of the morning. Like top.
But what? Lily means morning?
Yeah, basically, yeah.
So when I ask, they say good morning. Oh, yeah, just try to run away from what I'm saying.
I say top of the Lily.
Words are spells and shit, right? Which it is. And they be saying you're not supposed to say good morning.
Why are you not supposed to say good morning?
Because the morning. It's like, good morning. It's like programming and shit.
Amen. So where did Grand Rising come from?
That's what I'm saying. That's so I'm trying to figure out
who made Grand
like, you know what I mean?
Because who made Grand Rising up?
I don't know who made that shit up.
Like, but think about it though.
I feel like everybody just started saying that shit.
That shit popped up with the whole woke thing, the whole woke era. Like, Grand Rising King.
I was hearing somebody Queen. Say talk about this.
No,
shit
but see, because it probably get laughed out the park everywhere. Like that's why how deep
finally,
the program
it finally
is.
Hit somewhere.
Yeah, that shit hit the system. That shit ain't supposed to get in here. Keep on saying good morning. You know what I'm saying? That's
the
spell. It's already we already spelled up.
Okay, exactly.
So it's like Grand Rising is like
the break the spell.
It feel like a virus.
Yeah, like what the fuck?
Tell me good morning.
That's the Sharif and all that.
So what you
that's Sharif. Get out of here, Sharif.
So
that's crazy.
Yeah, we doing it up. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
funny, you said Grand Rising?
Nah, but I tried that shit for like 2 weeks. I couldn't.
Hey,
who you was hitting with that?
You was running around Grand Rising and niggas.
You know why you funny? Because you said that with my daughter. She was like before.
Oh yeah, yeah, I did.
Daughter.
I remember.
That did you say Grand Rising?
To me. Like, nah, nigga be having,
I got at this nigga before. Like, he had his kids and shit. I'm like,
that's funny. Though,
all that shit means something, bro. Words really
so
are
so. Wait, so okay, so Grand Rising is top of the morning. What's good night? How you say?
That's the funniest part right there.
Good night.
Think about it, they say weekends, like weekdays, like they work you out all through the week, and then it's with a weekend, and then you got Sunday.
What that mean, King?
But like, if you like Sunday,
King the one made up Grand Rising, man.
Yeah. Some nigga did, but man, shout out to get his energy. Shabazz, whoever, I'll fuck Shabazz. With it. Like, why y'all laughing at it, man? What's wrong with it?
I'm trying to figure out
what you said.
What's
like,
wrong with it though?
Is it just something new? So I was like, what?
Yeah.
Nah, I mean,
is it better than good morning? If we talking about words or spells,
that's way better than good morning.
So why don't y'all start saying Grand Rising?
Because we say top of the Lily.
Top of the Deleon.
We say
yeah.
top of the
y'all still
top.
Said
top of the Deleon.
Y'all said morning though, right?
Grand Rising, King.
Top of the Lily.
My Nubian sisters.
Grand Rising.
Cause I'm black, y'all. Yeah. I'm black, y'all.
That's
I'm
black,
I'm black,
shit,
I'm black, y'all.
Wacky
yeah, I'm brilliantly black, black of the black, 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 black. Yeah. Nigga, all that on the show.
Yeah, nah, that's some funny ass shit though, bruh. Getting the bitches with the Grand Rising sister. I heard, yeah, your retrograde is a what they say. The retrograde is. And I don't fucking know.
Mercury and
Mercury is in a retrograde.
Yeah, Python be talking all that stupid shit.
Python lost his dad. he was in there talking that stupid shit at the function last night.
Yeah, what man. What's your moon rising and all that? Nigga, take his hat off, reveal the star.
He showed the star.
All that stupid shit.
It was all yo coming out the side of his hat last night. That boiler room was going crazy on that motherfucking head. Hatching 4 eyes, dog. I'm like, dog, that's yo, homie.
Oh my God, bruh. Trill J sent 499. What's the difference between what Moosa did to Reason and what Adam did to AD and Terrell? Terrell said the CEO allowed to talk down on the employees. Shout out 18.
talking down. I don't think he was talking down.
Yeah, I don't get that question. I really don't get it. Like you can read it again or we can move on. Because I don't get
what their family built.
Yeah, what's the difference between what Musa did to Reason and what Adam did to AD and Terrell? Terrell said CEO. Is Musa not the CEO of TDE?
Next question.
And he wasn't pillow talking. He addressed the situation.
Nah.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah. Pete Griffin sent five. Kim, I love you to death, but.
But.
Kim, I love you to death, but. You might actually be more paused than Matt. Had me watching that Black Mirror's episode. I couldn't even watch the whole thing.
I couldn't even watch that motherfucker. But I never got into Black Mirror anyways, though. People said I'll be into Black Mirror, but I can't even get into it.
Did you watch that whole episode?
I wasn't even about to fuck with that story. That shit be fucking my exactly.
What story?
Weird shit. I was even about to fuck with that. That's why I put the fan on me. I was over here going through it.
He got
the shades off of some other shit.
He like, what's going on?
I'm feeling that empath.
Yeah.
When they truth in the detail.
He felt like the witches was tapping in with him from Morgan.
I'm tapped in, man.
B time saying 199. Is that 600 bins? Shaking my head.
Yeah, man.
My nigga Mom sent two. New beginnings never got old. No matter how many times I listen, this record is starting to feel the same. Shout out Reason. 2025, we gotta get a feature in. Stream Porches. Yeah, go Stream Porches, man. Shout out my nigga Mom.
Yeah, it's hard. I like that.
Key Dot sent 10. I told Terrell his suit jacket was disgusting for the news and Heather was pretty. He dead in my super chat ever since. Kima Blinka Bam's face ass nigga from Arthur. Everything scanners. Look it up.
Look it up. I like that.
Yeah, you know we did. He knew we wasn't gonna get that one, kid. Yeah, look it up though, nigga. Yeah. Did y'all look that one up though? That was gonna be the one.
That's funny.
Wait, what he said?
That nigga said Binka Barnes.
Binky Barnes.
Yeah.
Binky?
That nigga's he's telling what he up. Said. He correcting the Binky Barnes.
Well, I don't even know.
Cold DJ. Run that
back. Jody Goyard said 499. King. Nigga, what's the word with the phone call? Blessings. Y'all got the super chats now.
That's more see. Pun.
Tom Thompson 499. Shout out to you.
That look
Tom
like Tom. Pun more than King.
Let me see.
The smile. Oh, yeah, it's the pun. Smile. The smile make him look like pun.
That's funny though. That's funny. Motherfucker, bro. Tom Thompson 999. That's really pun.
The smile make him look like pun for sure.
That's bullshit. Oh, that nigga's intense. That's crazy.
That's funny, homie.
That nigga Tom Tom said, why TF don't sell merch? Or it's had AZ heat wave here to buy.
Pull this up, Mac, because it's funny.
I don't know what he tried to say.
Show the people.
Sell your hats. It's fire. The fans want to buy it. TF.
Somebody put the link in the bio. The merch link in the.
Put the link in the prescription. What's that nigga name?
He said he got
punched. That's funny. with a cold deal. We approaching a nigga with.
Cold deal.
Hey, let me ask you a question, TF, right? For as like the merch thing.
Right.
There to the Addison Times. Somebody seen a person say, hey.
What's that nigga name? Binky.
Did you come across somebody like that? The boarding room last night.
Binky Barnes.
And they like, hey.
Binky Barnes.
The package can come. They want their chili right there, though. Would you give it to them, or would you sell them right to the package?
I give him the option. If he wanted his chili, I'll just give him a chili.
You get chili right there?
Yeah. My fried shrimp, I'm about to go look it up.
Oh, even if I sent it off already?
Yeah.
If, like, a lot of times, like, when that shit be happening like that, like, I send it off and shoot them the bread back if they, if you know, if that's what they wanted, yeah. Or I just send them some extra merch.
That's what I do. Do you send extra merch every time I yeah. I fuck them?
Do y'all make them prove that they bought it?
Oh, it's a lot.
Nah, I ain't say, nah, nah,
so somebody could just come up to you like, "Hey, TF, I bought this shirt and I never got it."
Well, I know because I be in contact with, I stay in contact for the most part with motherfuckers. It's like, all right, well, shit, if your shit late, nigga, just holler and hit me. And
chat.
I stay in contact. It's not like a nigga like just in the shadows, like it's over with. You feel me? Because that don't be the case.
Okay, I got you. Ooh. I got you. I gotta get some merch. Shout out to somebody who made me something too. But
yeah, shout out to the people that's cooking up, man.
They sent it like the one you only could see it one time. I told him I wasn't fucking with
it. It's one of the bomb photos.
Who did this for you?
Somebody on Instagram. Shout out to Cut Up, but we straight. He told me to holler at him when I'm ready.
Yeah. Oh,
shout out to the chat, man. Y'all make sure y'all smash the like button.
Hey, pass me my phone too, Mac, when you can.
Merch is a hard game, man.
Huh?
Merch?
Oh, yeah, yeah, for sure.
I mean, not hard, like you can't do it, just like you gotta just be on it. Like,
yeah. I ain't wanna work with a nigga sending me shit that disappeared. What are we doing, man? Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, nah, for sure. It was just like a sample, I guess you could say.
No, that's out, man. What you mean?
But it was like a bomb photo or some shit. But I told him I wasn't fucking with it, but good
guess
looking.
And I'm dang like, at the bottom, like,
Yeah.
Yeah, that's funny as fuck. My nigga Shrimp Life sent two love from Fresno, California. You heard, keep doing what y'all doing, man.
Heard.
Shout out, bro. Fresno.
52 and 5 sent 199. What's TDE gonna do for Smack? He got no insurance. Smack got insurance, man. He getting taken care of. I just don't think the spot is a good spot. I'm assuming, but he good though, as far as I know. Tony Swisher sent 199. Bell got on the Richard Simmons shorts. Shout out, my nigga.
Hey, y'all ever had to go to Killer King Hospital?
Nigga, I grew up right there.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. I used to stay on 123rd Street at one point, like when I was real young and shit. And I used to be like the hospital for that's like around the corner, the block before the hospital. So I used to be, that was like the home hospital, my nigga. I used to stay in that motherfucker for real.
Yeah, I got my head buzzed one time. And I sat in that motherfucker for 12 hours and didn't get no stitches.
For real?
Yeah, they put a Band-Aid on my shit had just
stopped bleeding, huh?
Nigga. And I was a kid. They just put a Band-Aid on, like some sutures and a Band-Aid.
I got stitches right here. And that motherfucker.
And they was like, oh, yeah, well, just come back if you need stitches. Like,
just what? Come back, nigga. I put this Band-Aid on you, nigga.
I'm like, damn.
We forgot you was here, cuz.
For real.
Yeah, that's
shout out to Killer King for keeping the scouts.
They know they're going
to
get the business. Cold business.
For sure.
That shit was in the ER packed every day. That's where they took Kane when he got popped.
Nah, for real.
ER
that nigga was in there bleeding.
That's kind of crazy,
shit.
Dog. It's motherfuckers. It's people who got high jobs and shit that get pissed the fuck off if the ambulance is not being dispatched. Like, they'll have a bad day. They'll fuck up their whole business. And like, the ambulance was not getting dispatched.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like, y'all get what I'm trying
to say? Yeah.
That's crazy.
Because they just went on strike.
Yeah.
Basically, if they went on strike, how the fuck are you going to get the calls out and how they going to help the people that's in need?
Yeah. You're not getting paid enough. You just got to drive there yourself.
Yeah. My nigga DJ Choro sent 5. I saw a Tiny hotboxing in his whip at Jack and the Crack on Fig and Vernon.
That's what you didn't see, but shout out to you.
Hotboxing.
That's crazy.
That's
what I'm saying.
That's a crazy. That's
Jack in the Box is janky promoters because you can't even, you stuck.
Like Fig and Vernon.
Yeah, Fig and Vernon. That's right by the gas station. Jack in the Box, the Ross right there.
That is the Jack in the Box the nigga go to, though.
Yeah, 76
right next to it. Yeah.
Over there on bullshit.
Nah.
At work,
we get 2 tacos. Y'all got the munchie meal. Snoop Dogg up here.
Fig and Vernon, they just found a body in there.
Oh my!
Yeah, where?
Fig rest in peace.
That shit didn't even make the news.
Yeah, that definitely ain't make the news.
Yeah, let's get get them out the way. Yeah, get the drive back on.
You know, Instagram. They ain't gonna make like
million hits was there.
Huh?
Million hits.
Yeah. We found a body.
It was
Fig and Vernon, a nigga that just
be on you.
every scene.
He said, what? Nigga look like you. You got a sick pink, my nigga.
He be on live.
Yeah,
he be driving around. That's crazy. He just came to my algorithm. I just seen somebody going live and they got on the freeway like bought it on the 110. I'm like, who the fuck is this? Like, what's going on? But
I'm fucking him though.
I didn't stay on too long, but that's what he do. He just be sagging around looking for shit that's going on in the city.
Nah, he be that nigga. He like
the radio box.
You ever seen that movie Nightcrawler?
Yeah. Nightcrawler is crazy.
That nigga funny.
That's a good movie.
Okay. Yeah,
that's crazy. You ever seen him in person? Like,
that's a cold pop. Yeah, he came to the set and tried to interview some niggas before. A long time ago, like when he first was.
Did y'all interview with him?
I think that nigga H-Crown did. He chopped it up with him a little bit. I don't know how far deep they got into the whole supposed to be interview. I think they just end up chopping it up.
Shout out to Cut.
Shout out my nigga Crown.
My nigga Sleep Sinatra sent five. Bell got a cleanse from African Oba. What does that mean? For real, I got a joint with you. And Adonis, two love from 402. Love y'all.
That's a man.
Dillion.
You got a song with this nigga?
Shit, cool. That motherfucker.
Probably.
My nigga. K-Dot sent 199. I was gonna say Pun, but he ain't there. Shout out my nigga, I like Sprite. He sent 499. Can't compare Terrell or Musa to Dude 16 in the slightest. Terrell and TDE in the culture. Dude is an invasive cancer to the culture. And that's a fact. No cap. Yeah, y'all niggas funny for this picture on my nigga Pun.
That's good when he be smiling for sure.
Dance! That's funny. That's like with the lady knights of sin making them dance.
That's a hell of a picture right there. That's funny as fuck. That's funny as fuck.
You ain't even gonna do that.
Let's give our prayers too to the motherfuckers in Maui. Y'all see the fires and shit?
Yeah.
That nigga Dree was crazy. That's why we haven't been doing the congregation. This nigga Dreebo. Nah, he ain't stuck. He ended up getting back. He ended up flying back, but he had to leave all his shit out there, which is crazy.
Oh, they had to bounce like that?
Oh, it's crazy.
No, it's really
it's
wild.
A whole, like, it's ugly. Like, they said it was 80 people dead so far.
80?
Yeah, but he said it's going to get to the hundreds. And what's crazy, he said, I think he wanted to tell his own story on Monday. We supposed to still do the congregation Monday at noon.
Is that nigga birthday on Monday?
Yeah, it's his birthday. My birthday Tuesday. Congregation party August 19th.
Damn. When the party?
The 19th, next Saturday.
Saturday
you
coming
gonna,
up.
We gonna be able to get in? Niggas ain't gonna get left.
Keem already said he ain't coming or he busy or some shit. He already said he
there's something going on that day for sure.
I know you told me.
Yeah, but
it's straight if you can't make it. I ain't tripping.
It's gonna crack regardless.
Yeah. I feel like when the people that don't come, they just miss out.
It's gonna crack regardless.
But I feel like it's gonna
that's
be cool.
Supposed to be. Always crack.
Yeah. But that's y'all definitely. But yeah, he said he was about to fly back out there to try to get their shit. But they
damn, he gotta fly back out there.
Okay, how you gonna get his shit?
They can send me my shit.
Bruh, it's mayhem out there. It's like
they ain't tripping up.
That's the last thing on their mind.
A lot of people
gotta go get their shit then.
They gotta fly back.
That's what he said he was gonna do, but so they shut the roads down. They shut the roads down, so he didn't fly
it's
back.
Over out though, if it's like that type of shit.
They probably not even accepting flights in.
They
accept the flights in.
Whatever in the resort.
All through them bags.
Yeah, for sure. That's what I said. You just gotta hope that you feel me.
What they got?
Yeah,
like shit.
But yeah, nah, it's crazy. They said Mayweather saved some people on some shit or help some people out because it is crucial. So let's give our prayers out to them.
So where the bags at? The hotel or where them shits at?
He said at the resort. In the resort, he said they woke up and basically it was no power, and. When they left the resort to go somewhere where it was powered, then when they was about to drive back,
he posted a video of it when he was with his girl or some shit.
Yeah. When they was on the when they went where it was powered, then they was about to groove back to go
get that shit.
Yeah, to see if the what you call that power, and then that's when they said it just got dark on the roads and shit. And it, you know, out there it's just like two lanes.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. So shit. shut down or something. It's traffic. So they basically turned around and went the other way. They just left their shit.
Yeah, San Diego's a high power, you know, play. People didn't want to come up off that land. All the people
play. Damn, for real. That's what I said. How the fuck is
I was about to ask, what's that never happened. Made, or what was that fire about?
They said this the biggest fire in their history.
Yeah, but how did it start?
Somebody came to strip
somebody
that
said,
corporations. This how I feel.
Like that.
The
plane flew over, sprinkled the whole bitch, and dropped that match on that motherfucker.
The most flammable thing you could drop, they dropped off the sky.
Yeah, for real.
For
it to be a big
ass. They said it was like three different fires. He said
I was looking on Twitter, and it was a lady just collapsed just in the middle of the street. And motherfucker drove, like, look at the lady. He's like, man, it's over for her. Keep going. I'm like, damn.
She on fire?
Nah, she
probably just had
it. That's like the cycle of life, with what you were saying? You said,
what's there to eat? Unless it's, because in that type of situation, unless you saying on some save yourself type shit.
That's what they was on.
We're about to do big business. It's going to impact my families.
I would have stopped, though, me personally.
Oh, you mean like my
body? You would have stopped if you had your family in the car and stuff, too?
Because
then if you stop right there and then you drive down and then you stop again, or you like, shit, I'm full now.
That's too much.
I would have stopped and checked.
You can have my seat.
Yeah.
I would have stopped.
I'll carry you.
Because, like, nigga, if you already TIP.
Two hands. Yeah, that's
done. If you already TIP, it's over. Yeah, you can see, like, she was like, just like, you feel me? The dude wasn't with his family. He was with one of his homies.
I didn't see that, so I don't. Yeah. But that is crazy.
To be honest, I don't know who the fuck them people was, but they kept hauling on her.
Yeah, that shit wild, though. It's like, and that's an island, too. So I be thinking about when this fire is out here, when it be like from up north and that shit come all the way down to out here, be one big ass fire.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, damn, imagine if it was an island. It's over. Like, he said motherfuckers were jumping in the water and shit. It's like, yeah, ain't nowhere you could go.
I don't know where they think they gonna go hopping in that water. Where they swimming to?
Shit, it's like, what, you want to just get burnt refuge. Alive? You want to get burnt alive, or you want a chance, or that's a cold situation?
Or you
want to
jump in this boiling water?
Yeah.
I'm going to be a nigga with a boat. Fuck off.
Yeah, they said the people, the locals was tripping, though. They like, man, all you people's tripping on y'all luggage and flights canceled and vacations ruined.
We losing everything.
Like, yeah. These motherfuckers out here TIPing.
Big business about to come over there in a second. We got it. We got you. Don't worry about it. We're going to come in. We're going to help you out. We're going to give you a little extra, huh?
We're going to give y'all motherfuckers a...
But
let us get this, though.
Yeah.
Man, that's some wild shit, man.
Turf wars.
It's crazy. On a whole another level, though. Yeah. And, you know, we're going to give y'all some cash. I'm going to get relief, all that. Y'all be good, you know, but this us now.
Hey, Bell, can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
If one of your boys, you know, needed sunscreen put on their back, would you put it on their back?
Nah, man. Who putting sunscreen on their homie's back? You done that before?
No, I haven't.
I don't know what y'all talking about.
Sunscreen on the back is crazy. I gotta put sunscreen on your back, nigga. Hell no.
Fuck,
nigga? You better get sunburned, this motherfucker. You better get
water. Yeah, for sure.
What's up with?
Hell no.
Would you do it?
Yeah, I put sunscreen on it. If, like, my nephews and shit, something like that.
No, he said your boy, your homie.
It's the relationship. Like, I felt like some motherfuckers not even flexible to do that shit. So, yeah, I would.
No, but he didn't say your nephew. My little nephew.
I'm saying about the same. If I, because the only reason you wouldn't is what? Because
you put
what?
Sunscreen on Tony's back?
What I put, if I feel like Tony couldn't reach his back.
He'd be like, hey.
You know, you can put some on the tile and.
But y'all saying it like whatever. I'm talking about we gonna get the sunscreen on your back, my nigga. Like for sure. That's what I'm saying. It's just your back, so why wouldn't y'all do it?
I don't know.
Man, we supposed to be black. We supposed to be cool with the sun.
Oh, that's why.
That sunscreen shit ain't for me.
Yeah. Or you? That's what I'm saying.
I remember you telling a story about
people don't be getting that when I say
that.
Like, you ain't putting sunscreen on.
I know you never done that.
Yeah, but, I don't do that shit.
No. But I remember you. how do you say it? You said some of your partners.
You know remember. They got spray though. Don't they got spray?
Spray. They got
all
spray.
That. That's what I was answering. I'm telling y'all, like, I'm not.
But you said
why y'all running away from like putting sunscreen on your somebody like your boy's back?
So you wait. King said
so you put lotion on somebody's back.
He knew some dudes that put lotion.
Nah, I ain't letting him put lotion on nobody's back. I'm talking about somebody. Obviously, it's like now, what y'all talking about? A want or hey, I need the sunscreen. Y'all talking, I'm talking so about a nigga needs the sunscreen. He can't get on his back.
Why
you thought your homeboys were strange that you said was putting lotion on they, on each other's back or some shit?
That was a want.
How you know?
I see it. That's your homie too.
I don't know the story. I never heard that story.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's funny as hell. Yeah.
I never heard that story.
You never heard that story?
I just said I never heard that story.
I want the homie to put lotion on my back. It's crazy.
That's different. That's
why is that different from a nigga putting screen? What'd you say?
Because it's like what I'm saying.
Where you come from? Where you get this from, man?
Keem got this. This is everything Keem said. I'm merely repeating what he said.
He probably don't remember he said that.
Said what?
Everything I said. Even with the, you said you seen some dudes putting lotion on each other's backs. And then
yeah, them niggas got caught. I was there. When I come to the yard, yeah, I peeked over the gate because we supposed to be going to the job. The homie driving though, you know what I'm saying? It's his day to drive.
Shout out Carpool, man.
These niggas back
man.
There with the Cokes on.
With the Cokes. So y'all, they getting lotion up to go to work.
Nah, the Cokes, them things, the clocks.
The cloaks.
Yeah, the cloaks on. Nah, because it was just crazy. Shit. Like, them niggas, I look over the gate and type shit. And I see these niggas, three. Niggas all putting the lotion on each other's back, like type shit. Or baby oil. That's crazy.
That's what I'm saying.
Right? Oh. I'm like, yo, what? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, type shit.
And you that, over the gate seeing all this.
Yeah, that's up. I ain't gonna say
like, what y'all doing. Like,
who
y'all
is?
Doing?
But he brought that story up. I ain't gonna say who it is. Are you?
I don't know this story. Why you keep putting me in? I don't know.
You,
I just heard that story from
that nigga. Well, he was one of the three. He lying.
I'm not lying. I don't know that story, my brother.
He knew all three of the people?
Being one of the three is cool.
Oh, yeah, he
said, y'all got me fucked up. I would never let nobody put no man one of the no three. Man.
You never what?
Let no man put lotion on my back. Or sunscreen, none of that.
Not even if you even needed it, huh?
Nor would I rub lotion on the man or
so many other people.
I've never had lotion on my back. Other than
hashtag Mac.
Yeah, I don't know why. It came crazy as a motherfucker. That is some crazy shit, though, bro.
That's funny.
That nigga funny, homie. You trying to throw a fucking narrative in the air.
What narrative? This everything you said. I never said nothing.
Huh?
I never said anything. You said all these.
You a funny nigga, dog.
Why,
shout
kid?
Out to the homies, though.
Why I'm funny?
Shout out though. To the homies, dog.
What I do? What I do?
Hey, funny.
But you cool, it's like, you low-key a contradiction because you said...
I'm always a contradiction. Because
you can't fault them niggas for whatever the fuck they was doing if you wouldn't have partaken that same thing.
I said what I said, man. You know, that's
you
what
get
I'm saying.
That's, really my, that's my
that's
argument.
That's why I love me. Did you hear what I said? I said it's a difference between the need and the want.
I don't understand. We speaking to the action.
Huh?
We speaking to the action. You're rubbing, you're doing it literally what they doing.
You think that's gay or something?
I don't think nothing of it.
So you do think something of it?
I'm talking to you about what you brought up. So I'm trying to understand.
I didn't bring this up.
Why did you critique these niggas in that light?
I didn't bring that up.
You did. You brought.
I did not bring that up, bro. You just brought that up. What are you talking about?
I know. I learned these stories from you. So I'm really because you just said this yesterday about this. You willing to rub a nigga back with sunscreen? You said that yesterday, and I'm like, why he acting like the other niggas he mentioned was crazy? Because you willing to do it too. And you know, sunscreen, that's like thick, so you gotta really.
You didn't get that dick, get this. Hey, man. That's why I said a need or a want, my boy.
So, what would make a nigga need the sunscreen on his back?
Hey, shout out to my boy, man.
All right, let me ask you now.
I'm just saying.
What would make a nigga need sunscreen on their back?
Maybe he can't reach, you know what I'm saying? He can't reach. Probably can't.
So, what would make a nigga need lotion on their back? What would make a nigga need the nigga to rub lotion on their back?
That's
bro,
crazy.
You taking it somewhere.
I'm just asking questions. Like, you was ridiculing the lotion niggas, but you the sunscreen nigga.
How ridiculing them?
How far down they back you putting the lotion?
Hashtag Magua.
That's crazy. That is crazy.
That's the hey, listen. Hey, listen.
Oh my God, homie. Shout out to the homies,
Mr. Child,
I'm telling you, man. Mac, the funniest guy. Yo.
What? That was hilarious.
I didn't do anything.
God damn.
The funniest. I'm going to merely give you credit.
What I do, though? You like how that motherfucker tied in?
That's funny, homie.
Yeah, no, that's a good one, man. But hey, man, like I said, I never done that. I'm not here looking to do that and all that, man.
No, I didn't never say you did that. Though. I thought it was crazy that you said you would, though. I was like, what the fuck is
I'm not trying to be funny right now, but the only reason I said that, what I would, bro, I think clearly both his arms ain't working like that. Maybe he can't. Like I was saying.
Oh, so
like,
you would.
If he, you know what I'm saying?
So you saying that you would do your real Terrell back?
Nigga, that was the whole question. He said if he
oh,
needed it.
Oh, he telling he you to rub it. His back is what you took that as.
No.
Wait a minute. So what are you telling me right now, kid? So I didn't know this was yeah. Like these, I thought this was all hypothetical.
It's a story.
Wait.
It's a storyline.
No, wait. I thought this was hypothetical.
It's all hypothetical.
No, it's not. When you said like you would rub his back, it's not hypothetical no more. Like you saying you would literally rub Terrell back right now. With sunscreen. Cause you said I didn't know you was personalizing that question, like saying, you get what I'm saying? Like his arm was messed up, so I will rub your back, King. Grand Rising.
Hey man.
You are a funny ass nigga.
I don't know what kind of narrative y'all want. Y'all want a narrative, it's like
Grand Rising.
Grand Rising is crazy as fuck. They walking up to the homie. Grand Rising.
Let me rub your back.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. But this don't even know.
No, though. Either way, no, I'm going to be honest, though. That's for that one, I'll fuck with that, though.
That's all I'm saying.
Like, but, I ain't going to even.
Man,
no far shit, though. But I fuck with you. You a young nigga for that, for sure.
Hey, y'all see the other young dude that passed out having a heart attack, too?
All over the back, like a...
Say it again.
The other young dude passed out getting heart attack.
Just put that
same thing like LeBron's son did.
No, I can't say that again.
No, it was another dude that another young basketball player. He's like 17. He passed out too.
Oh yeah.
Like he was at a basketball workout too. Is this what happening with like the people that's getting the COVID shots?
That's what they trying to say. It's that jab.
Yeah.
These are
the long term effects that's happening right now. You got the jab. It's like you could be up out of here. You going too high power. You doing too much.
It's probably just narrowing down on that type of blood.
The high power people.
Yeah, like let's go do what it's supposed to do. They're supposed to kill everybody.
It's a neutralizer.
Yeah.
So niggas can't grow no more. It's like, well, let's take out everybody that can afford. If it's progression, if he could have progression to the...
All the threats.
Yeah, all the threats. Let's just take
plus
him out right now.
Plus $5 is up. They got it.
Or though, Bell, these niggas are just not shedding light on everybody else that it's happening to because they're not like high-profile names.
So it probably been happening to
people.
Yeah,
it's probably happening on a major scale, but they just don't care to... Just like niggas said, what just happened on that body on, what is it, Vernon and Fig?
Yeah.
That could be the same scenario, just like niggas don't care to announce it.
So some stories just going to get out there just based on who you are.
Exactly. Because everybody we're hearing about it, what, Bronny?
Bronny. This other dude, he was like a five-star.
He was number
star.
Two in his spot, yeah. in his wherever, his in his whatever the fuck, but he was like number 30 or some shit as far as the player rank go.
He's like number two in his country. I mean, his country, his state.
Mm-hmm. He was really the guy. So rest in peace to him, man.
That's crazy because on Wednesday, I went to Vegas. Yeah, Wednesday. Tuesday night after I left here.
Was it hot?
I got
It was crazy hot.
Yeah, it was hot. It was hot out there. Basically, my sister,
that,
husband.
Did you see that little ball shit?
Yeah, the spirit. That yeah. It looked tight. It was lit
that
up.
Shit. That shit looked wild.
Sometimes it was just red though. Sometimes they had an eyeball. Or they was telling me that sometimes it's different, but it just looked like Mars.
That's hard. Though.
Yeah, it was still tight. It looked better on the
cause
picture
you can see it from
though.
The angle from a far
Yeah. When you, it just looked like a big red light when you driving by it. But basically, my sister's husband passed away on some shit. And then I was just like, I was wondering, like, damn, when people pass away, I'm like, damn, are we supposed to just go out there to Vegas right now, like, for our condolences type shit? But we end up going, and it's crazy looking at pictures, like, going through the whole death shit and then looking at the pictures that they gonna use for the obituary and shit. It's like, you never know what picture you took that's gonna be
used for the obituary.
Yeah, and that was crazy, just going through all the pictures looking and for them to all agree on one. And it's just like, damn, it's like niggas take pictures all the time. You don't never know which picture is gonna be that's, yeah, you're not gonna see it, but take pictures though, for sure.
Memories. Now, I also asked that COVID question too, because I'm trying to put my daughter in school right now. So I'm going up there, and they like, she gotta have this done. She gotta have a vaccination.
Oh, for real?
No, that's bullshit.
So I'm trying to see, kids gotta be jabbed up to go to school right now.
But no, that's what they say. They like, she gotta have this done. She gotta have that done. I'm like, damn.
Nah, I don't believe that. Unless that's just a new narrative they pushing.
District? What school district?
Shit, I mean, she's trying to go to like some. Her mom's trying to put her in like Montessori school. She infant. She little.
Okay. Well, that's probably probably got their own rules going on.
Cause mine ain't one of them.
Montessori.
Y'all smash that like button, chat.
Yeah, no, they gonna get her together. So, yeah. Especially if she already advanced, like in real life.
No, yeah, she do it up. But yeah. I'm just like, damn. If I get her to jab, then is it?
Nah, don't do that.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do it. But it's just like, damn, they trying to put
they
that on
still
your
doing that.
Yeah, they trying to put them. I mean, that's what they said.
That's crazy.
I did like 3 school tours this week. I mean, yeah, this week, and it's just like
all of them pushing the same line.
Yeah, the chat said, don't do that shit, Bell. Chat, what y'all think, man?
They like.
That's really a cold narrative. If they really pushing that agenda on the kids.
I'm like, damn, she 2 and a half. And she already got to get this done. I'm like, this is crazy.
And it's that's mandatory. The system, though. So it's like.
But it's like, you got to put her in school because it's like.
So,
natural progression.
So you can homeschool.
And you system up. You. It is what it is, then. I know you'll get here. I know.
Eventually, you're going to come back.
And I'm 100% sure it's got charter schools that's available and all kind of other shit, because they said charters is where it's at now. Man.
Yeah.
Man, go get one of them throw off bunk ones.
Yeah.
Fall in there with the copies of that.
Yeah.
You feel me?
I mean, that's going to be the plan. I'm just asking, is it, you know, I know you got youth. I know.
But nah, yeah, my, she was in there since she was what, like, maybe 16 months.
Yeah.
Since she was a baby.
Yeah.
She's going to be 4.
She
been knowing these people, and it's never, they ain't never switched nothing up.
But that's what I'm saying. She probably got there 16 months. That's like one and a half.
No, it's not even one and a half.
1 and 2 months.
That's 1 year old.
Yeah. So it's just like, I'm going there now. I'm like, damn, she got to have this. She got to have that. I'm like, that's just crazy. That's just crazy that they, you know, that's what they trying to do. And then you see all this shit happen. Like Max said, you don't know what's going on else in the world. You feel me? It's not like, you feel me? They will never know. We don't know how many infants this is affected, or if people that's just not TIP, and they probably just got certain type of deficiencies going on over time of mess with your spinal cord, or she can't do this now, she can't do that now. I'm just like, damn, that's crazy.
That's a fact.
Yeah, that's crazy as a motherfucker though, bro. Yeah, so I don't know. I don't even know what advice I could give to somebody going through that right there, though. That's actually some wild shit right there, man. Like, what would you do, Kim, if you was in that situation with your little ones? Like, they're requiring them motherfuckers to get jabbed up in order to attend school.
Because nobody here got the shot, right?
But
you got the shot, Tiny?
Yeah, I got the shot.
That nigga was like,
hey, he quiet as motherfucker.
That nigga sitting there.
Hey, but look. I would say this though. I got one dose. I never did that.
I got the boosters, man. I'm buff.
Because I didn't know about the fake cards.
Your job right now requires you to have it?
It did back then. I mean, they ask you.
The impression that you are right now?
They ask you.
he is
got a job.
He jacked up.
You said you didn't get it. I mean, I get it.
Yeah. But I don't even know if it's a... Oh, it might be a requirement. Yeah, I'm jabbed up. Yeah.
We're like, where you go? Where you go to get it? The doctor?
Yeah.
CVS?
Nah, doctor.
Damn, bro, that's crazy.
How you feel?
When I got it?
Yeah.
Stop searching.
Sick?
Nah.
I feel flavored up.
Flavored up is crazy.
Flavored up.
Nah, I mean, it's not a funny subject though.
Why?
Nigga, don't laugh at me, nigga.
What though?
I mean, you think it's funny?
The shot?
Yeah.
The shot hilarious.
Yeah. So you don't believe in vaccines and shit?
I do believe in certain ones. Not that one.
Not that one because it was the first go around.
Yeah. They was like offering free lap dances and shit for that motherfucker.
So, yeah. Hey, yo, so Tiny, what did you get for your jab?
Like, what deal was the one that enticed you to get you in that door?
It wasn't no deal. It was really just my family.
Okay,
really.
But see, no, we actually did you get it from your job. Like, did you get it because your job said you had to get it?
Nah, I mean that happens with get like my job asked me for it, but I got it from my family though.
Your family convinced you.
Yeah.
Boy, I'm walking this goddamn out.
Yeah, nah. My shout out to my mom. She in the medical field and all that, so she was like,
yeah, shout out.
So you know, it's pros and cons. I ain't gonna say it's
100%. It is pros and cons.
So, because I wasn't for it. I really wasn't for it. That's why, you know, I really wasn't for it, but she really was pushing the issue on some shit. Like.
So, moms was ground level seeing all that shit.
Yeah.
So, was she speaking on, like, all the people that was going out that really wasn't even going out due to COVID?
That's some wild shit, though.
She didn't say. She didn't get in like in that detail. Like these motherfuckers ain't really done because of this. They done because of this. Nah, it wasn't like that.
She was just saying it's a storm coming.
She was just saying like it's better to be. But she get the flu shot. Like that's her whole thing. She wanted it.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, some people for sure stand by all that shit.
They just
feel like, hey, they said it. That's what it is. And you get a couple casualties, then like it's for sure what it is. But just the flip side to that, motherfuckers who don't believe in it and nothing happened, you know what I'm saying? So clearly what y'all saying ain't all true. So some
Well, who's saying?
What the they people. Saying, like the pushing that narrative, like you gotta get this or
Oh yeah, nah, nah, nah. It's not
I caught COVID before. I feel like everybody caught COVID before.
Yeah.
I don't think I caught COVID.
Never not
once. I don't think
I've caught it before.
I mean, I really feel like it's to each his own. I did take it though, it was like
you was whooped?
For a day I was whooped. Like I was hot. It was like it was funny though, cause when I'm about to get the shot and shit, I'm acting all like a boulevard bitch. I'm like, oh no, no, no. At the doctor all scared.
How you doing it?
No. But then, boom, yeah, I got the jab. And then I was like, I was hot that I got the jab. But then it was feeling. Then I thought it was my mentality, though. I thought it was really my, like, I feel like your mind is really everything. So
how you feel about it now, though, in hindsight?
In hindsight, I wouldn't have did this shit.
So your mama say no. Still, I want you to do this. Would you get it?
So nah. In hindsight, no.
No, now.
So you feel like your
now,
mom, your mom.
Nah,
your
nah.
Your mom swindled you in that jab.
I mean, she thought that's what was best. I mean, it could have been what's best too. It's not 100. Y'all
niggas still don't
y'all
know.
Yeah, basically.
They don't like that. Can't keep your fucking mouth.
Yeah, basically.
No, because laughing ain't.
Laughing is bad.
Keep your fucking mouth.
I'm not laughing, but what am I laughing at though?
That's why I asked you.
A funny nigga, man.
I asked you, "Well, you think the jab is funny?" You say, "Yeah, it's hilarious." I literally asked.
Yeah, for a good. I get it though. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't want my mama to get it, but hey.
Oh, shit. And your moms don't like him too, though, huh?
Well, no, cool. She fuck with
she cool
him.
She cooler now. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because I wasn't gonna fuck with that nigga too though no more.
Because I had to remember moms do be tapped in sometimes.
Yeah. Shout out moms. Everybody, shout out moms in the chat.
Yeah, but, nah,
it's not really funny. I'm just bullshitting, cuz. I'm bullshitting, man. I definitely give, like, in hindsight, I wouldn't have did it because I already, part of me was saying don't do it in the first place anyway. But she, like I said, she in the medical field. She broke it down better. Like, I was listening to her more than I was listening to, what's the motherfucking name? Dr. Shafee. What the fuck was his name?
Sebi. Oh, Schaefer, the guy.
The nigga that be, yeah.
I don't even know the nigga. Everybody, that's why I was laughing at everybody. I was just, look what's going on with that nigga. He got a whole goddamn RICO case.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I get to laugh at that.
What was his narrative? What he was on?
Get that shit.
He made the shot.
Top op. And I'm letting you know, I got a little, for my resources and all my detail, you better get that motherfucker. Yeah, Dr. Fawcett.
Fauci. There you go. Yeah. So, like I said, I was listening more to my mom than more than. you know, I'm gonna fuck up some shit. But that's what it is though. I mean, I'm still here. Shit, I don't feel like.
Nah, it's tea. For sure. But I don't know.
I mean,
especially
for now,
if you didn't, for the people that didn't go through the whole process, it's better. The one who got the, you know what I mean. The whole combo.
Oh yeah.
Like, damn, they probably
got the shot. Still got. Why you was laughing earlier at me though?
Huh?
What you was laughing at?
No, that's just some funny shit. You just funny as fuck.
What I do? I really, I was like, what's him laughing at?
He was crying laughing.
Yeah,
too.
I was really lost though. Like, what was that about?
That's what I'm saying. What you doing? Why you doing that? You funny as fuck to me. You had said something, and it triggered the thought.
Okay, I don't remember that.
You gonna ever show us the what's the name though?
What?
You gonna show us any of those pictures, dog?
What pictures?
Your pops last week here.
What pictures?
From the Jesky.
Yeah.
Why y'all keep. What's up? I don't understand why y'all so infatuated with this Jesky's trip.
We would have never known about that story, bro.
About what story?
About you going out there to go see your pops and shit. He was like, looking forward to fucking with
him. We was supposed to go stream. We was supposed to go stream
bro,
and shit.
Saying. Then he gonna come back and like, just like, I don't know, bro. Why you do that? Like,
why'd I do what, though? You know that jet ski trip was for one of the companies. Like, it wasn't that. It was like we went out there with Exotic 710. It wasn't nothing. So I don't know what.
So you didn't invite your pops?
Nuh-uh.
His pops run Exotic 710.
Yeah, I don't know what's the narrative.
This nigga funny.
He was all under the pressure. He was going through his pops' birthday, right?
Yeah.
That wasn't the same thing.
That's what he told us.
We talking about that. We want pictures from that trip.
From what trip?
At his birthday party.
Why y'all want to see pictures from
because
that?
Because like, nigga, you had energy, and then you came back with like niggas was wrong for asking. Like, you know what I'm saying?
I never said y'all was wrong. I don't understand.
So show
like,
us pictures.
Why do you want to see pictures, Cabe? I don't understand. Like, show me Ron Isley.
Show me that nigga. That nigga running around with his drawers on in the crib. Serenading your mama. Show me pictures of that. That's what I want to see. The breakfast he's making in the morning.
Why you on him?
Why I can't be?
Why you on him, dog?
You think he hitting your mom?
He's definitely hitting his mom.
Huh?
You think he hitting your mom?
What's
going on, man?
Do you think he hit his mom?
Crazy. Just got hot.
Yeah, I get hot.
You looked up and looked down.
This is crazy.
Here, right here. All right, right there. Put this to smack.
Oh. Maggie!
Put on speak.
Oh, hold on. My fault. I ain't got this nigga new number stored. Yo.
Nigga, you see me calling. He's 34 to me. I ain't
got. Hey, I didn't know. I swear to God, I didn't know that was you, dog.
Smacky.
My nigga Smacky in this bitch. We on live, too, Smack.
Think I don't know, bitch. I watch everything.
Oh, my fault.
I'm updated.
I'm still in the loop. Pause.
Yeah, shout out to my nigga, man.
He's still in the loop.
He's still in the loop. You could have done yours.
No, I was sure. I thought it was.
What'd you say, Smacky?
I'm so used to
Bell back there.
Yeah, that's my nigga Bell in the kids.
What's the deal, man?
Smack down.
What's the deal, Smack?
It's a her.
I don't think he can hear you, too.
What's the deal, Smack?
What's going on, young man?
I'm good, man. You know, I'm up here streaming with the fellas, man. How you doing, man? You gotta keep your head up in there, man.
One day at a time, young man.
Yeah. That nigga, you're a veteran D.O. language now.
I like to hear that good spirit, man. You feel me? You gotta keep that up.
I'm real young. I'm real. Tell that boy, TF, man, you gotta call me back so I can lock his number.
Hold on.
Nah, Smacky, you got my number. Use the other one.
No, I didn't get the store. I was asleep, young man.
Like it ain't in his recent calls.
Yeah, make sure you tap back in out of respect.
Nah, yeah, I got you. How you feeling?
I'm blessed, young man.
Shout out,
my
boy.
Send my love on
P-I-R-U.
Shout out, on Payru.
All right, hey, T gonna come up there. T coming up there to see you, right? Oh, she on the East Coast now. You know, T was trying to come see you.
T?
She was trying to come see you.
They
didn't tell you?
Nah, tell her for
that. That's crazy. Okay, I'm gonna get to that though. Yeah. I don't know. She told Terrell and Heather she was trying to come see you.
Man, tap in with her, tell her pull up, King. Give her my name and tell her pull up. Let's get to that.
Hang up on that nigga.
Hey, Smack.
Shout out Smacky.
You got that, Smack. I ain't gonna even say nothing.
That was funny as fuck.
Yeah.
Oh my god. We're gonna read a couple super chats. My nigga Goldie T Slime Boss sent 199. Fish Sticks in the chat. Shout out Milky. Dizzy McGuire sent 3. Would you DJ a set for Terrell in the morning, and where do you think he should move the show to? I don't know where he plan on moving the show to. I heard that shit over with for all that shit with the playing music. When he saying that shit?
Yeah, but I think it's somewhere around there. If he go Patreon, I'm old, right?
I don't know how that shit, cause he won. I thought it was possible. Yeah, now. Nah, but
I said that from the jump. I'm like, I don't know how you gonna get that off. Period. Cause like, it's still labels. You still playing music, so.
And they getting paid for the songs being played.
Who?
The labels. They getting percentages of their songs.
No, they want percentage of this. What you got? Too. You got this program you're running. Okay. Now you're gonna be putting artists against artists. We don't even want next to my artists.
Oh, that type of shit. Because now they're looking at that like it's programming.
Yeah, you doing your own playlist and all that. We gotta. What you doing, bro?
Oh,
yeah.
So they already tapped in about
with these
shit.
Niggas. You can't. Hell yeah, you can't do that.
That's
but if you do Patreon mode, I'm thinking you possibly or something. Maybe.
You can do.
Damn, that's some cold. That's some cold politics.
Yeah, like, that's crazy.
I don't even want my shit played after or before that.
I didn't know it'd be like that.
Yeah, no, that's crazy though.
Yeah.
But would I pull up on that shit? Yeah, I would if it makes sense for sure. My nigga Lewis Lemon saying 199. Dance. Yeah, that nigga pun. He real dictator over there. King funny. Patted my stick sent $2. Matt. That's his name. Mac, where your friend you used to do content with been? His name was B or something, and he had long dreads back in the day, like 2012, 2013. I think he was from your section and funny as fuck.
Oh,
my nigga B Rich, man, bro. I don't know, man. Niggas really can't find B Rich. I've always been trying to tap in with my nigga. He really dedicated right now. He got his kids and shit like that, bro. Ducked off. I don't know, man. I've been tapping in with his family and shit. I can't find this nigga.
How long?
For a minute. For some years, actually.
Hey.
But I deal with his family, though.
But they say he good? Like,
yeah, he good, though. Like, I be sending this dumb bitch be all on my page lurking in the story and shit. Like, but I think I understand what's going on with this nigga, though.
He don't fuck with you?
Hey,
no, he do, though. It's deep in the rap.
Hey, King, what was Mac Boy name that used to pull up with this nigga all the time? Had the motherfucking flatbed Toyota.
Oh, Joker, my nigga.
What's
Savvy.
Been up with that nigga, man? You remember that nigga?
Yeah, Savvy.
Arabian Nights.
Arabian Nights.
Bro, yeah. Doing his thing, man. That nigga, he moved in with his lady. I still be chopping it up with my nigga and shit like that. He just locked in, you know, trying to grow. So the nigga just been locked in with work and trying to deal with his girl.
Yeah,
right now,
that nigga
like
was
that.
The number one Ninja Turtle, nigga.
Nah, that's my nigga, though. I'm going to get him on this stream shit with me, though. I'm going to definitely incorporate that nigga into this shit, too, though. I fuck with, bro. That's
he be tapped
nigga.
In?
Yeah, he tapped in. I still chopping up with this nigga till his day.
Okay.
That's still my boy and shit like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I ain't seen that nigga in like 3 years.
I know, bro. It got, because you got to know, Scandemic hit. That nigga had the, you know, regular job shit, so it really, that was a big shift in that nigga whole situation.
That's a Scandemic.
Yeah, man, so nigga had to figure that shit out, but he doing his thing, though, 100%. Shout out to my nigga Sav, too, though. My little Arabian Night nigga.
My nigga Jafar.
Jafar, he really was Jafar, though. That nigga Lord A sent 5. Tell a story how you beat up them studs again, TF. TF really a legend, bro. He got like the. I can't wait for the TF, the discography, bro.
Nah, yeah.
Or biography. Which one is it? Biography?
But it wouldn't be an autobiography. I mean, autobiography is which one?
I think that's the one written by you.
By you? You would, yeah, would y'all do one of those?
A biopic. That's what like somebody else.
So if a biopic came out on y'all right now, after you checked out.
I got one in the works right now.
How authentic is it?
Hey, I got one in the works.
I don't think I'm going to exaggerate nothing. It'll probably be like, it ain't going to be 100% to the T. But it's gonna be some shit in there, though. It's gonna be scary.
This is the story of
yeah,
the
and
fly.
I'm gonna have probably Sam Jackson narrating that motherfucker.
You gonna put it on Tubi?
That'll be tight.
Why would you put it on Tubi? Why are you laughing?
No, I'm asking because that's where it seemed like people putting shit on right
now. Why did I laugh?
Yeah.
Oh, I was laughing at how hard he worked. Like, that they really got bad shit going on. Like,
fuck me, yeah, I like that. Yeah. I believe.
You. What?
I believe.
Like, yeah, it's too much tripping the details with my nigga. Like, I'm like, that damn nigga now he got another story.
Yeah, nah, sure. But yeah, no bullshit. I was capping about the Sam Jackson shit, but like, we nigga got really one in the mix though for sure.
Who would you want playing you, King?
Playing me?
Yeah.
The nigga from Power?
Pick. Yeah.
Who? Nah, it was the light skin nigga.
No,
it's gonna be Terrence Howard.
Howard from Empire. Why you go to Terrence Howard though?
I'm not talking about from Empire.
He said Power though, but so what made you just choose Terrence Howard? No, that's who you gonna have playing you.
Yeah.
Oh,
You think he a good actor? You think he can act?
I
think Terrence Howard cold.
Okay,
dedicated man. He's dedicated man.
That's funny as fuck.
Like,
oh my god.
Get off me.
I really
I'm dedicated,
out.
Man.
I'm best man.
We present now, perfect,
that's
man.
He got all kind of arguments. Get off of me, man. I'm dedicated. That's really some funny ass.
So
shit,
like though. We was in the movie Best Man and shit, right? Yeah. We was all playing roles. Yeah, like Terrence Howard. Like, what would your role be?
So you Terrence Howard?
Yeah, I'm Terrence Howard.
Okay.
Who would you? I think it's enough of us in here. Who would you?
I'm the one with the dreads.
Tastes like Kinder.
Wait for that lap dance.
Who you are? TF and Matt.
I'm the nigga that wrote the book.
Dang, I was gonna say that. Golly. The wrote the book is crazy.
I wrote the book, nigga.
How many motherfuckers is left?
The nigga who fucked.
And the nigga who bitch me is.
Yeah, who wrote the book. I fucked your bitch. You know what I'm saying?
The
nigga
has
to go to the table.
Yeah.
And let that
bag
come up.
Oh, nigga, all truth to the details, man.
Yeah. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Damn,
that's a cold movie though. Like, it's everybody's secrets out on wedding day.
Damn.
Hey, while we here, then, right? Would y'all like?
Hey, turn that, hit the AC.
Oh, man. Yeah. Damn, that was when Smack called. It is hot.
Yeah, it's cracking outside. All right, what I was going to say, so would y'all let one of your homies' girl come to your crib and hang out? Ex-girl, or a girl, I don't know.
Ex-girl?
Yeah, ex-girl in like 10 years.
Hang out, Dolo?
I don't
me and her?
Dolo, party.
This one of your homie girls?
Yeah.
This already been going on, or this just popping up?
I don't know what's been going on.
Only way I can see that possibly happening is if her and my girl is
they
good.
They cool?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Other than that, no. Nah.
Yeah, no, that's out.
Yeah.
That nigga Joe did. You seen Joe did ish like that, right?
Yeah, that was funny as fuck.
What was that
I
about?
I think that was crazy. I think that episode was old, too.
That was an old episode.
Yeah, just starting to hit.
That nigga Joe wasn't a funny ass
nigga. When he got at him?
No, that was a resurfaced. That was a new one. But that topic was, they spoke on it before.
It's tight,
back
though, because it's funny, too. He tried to play it cool that first go around.
Yeah. He got out of there that first go around.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Then he just got hot. I guess he just... Like, hold on, fuck all that, my boy. But yeah, nah, Joe out of pocket for that.
Fuck
you know
all
what
that,
saying? But
boy.
Joe, he strike me as a nigga that was like that. He might have changed his ways, but he definitely.
Yeah, and that's why he probably
like
get.
That.
That's why he got so hot. That's why he's so triggered, because he knew in hindsight he's like, oh, that was nasty work.
I feel like
doing it like that.
Yeah. He don't even want that on his jacket. Like,
and
don't even.
He brought it up in like national television, basically.
Yeah.
Damn. But he kind of. I mean, he. I guess he was hot, but when he was saying like you should thank me for not fucking your bitch and all that, that's like,
oh, he said that to
Ish? I never seen
you should be thanking me.
I gotta go watch that episode.
You should be thanking. That's what I'm saying. See,
yeah,
but
yeah.
Well, so you already, character so he, already was already there.
So you already knew the intentions too. Like, she coming over here, she ain't like, we about to smoke hookah.
Some niggas just get a high off
he
of
finna smoke hookah.
Then they gonna knock a nigga bitch.
I mean,
yeah, like, because you already just eyeing her. You just couldn't keep your eyes off.
Yeah, I don't even like really talking to niggas' girls.
Yeah.
Like, to be all the way honest, I don't even like that. That's just weird to me.
But I mean, in theory too, though, it's not supposed to matter. We talked about it before. It's not supposed to matter if it's your ex from 8 years ago or whatever. Is it really supposed to matter? What you mad at now?
Was it his ex from 8 years ago? I think it was his
girl for 9 years.
It was his girlfriend of nine years ago.
Damn, they was damn near married.
Yeah, nine years.
I'm saying though, but when y'all break up, right?
But not 9 years though. The 9 years
it don't matter. I'm talking about when y'all
different.
Break up though. So the breakup not real. Breakup's not real then.
Mm-hmm. I mean, 9 years you can't break up with nobody.
Nigga might still be connected.
Yeah, Bell, nigga, he all Bell, all you edition.
Nigga what? Might be still sneak
all up in them bushes looking in her window. 9 years.
Coming over there, fake seeing the dog.
Coming over there, fake seeing the dogs. Coming over there, seeing niggas at the party wearing a costume.
Oh shit!
I'm saying 9 years.
God damn.
Hey, yo, kid, I swear to God.
Hold up.
Hey, yo, I did not know you had on a fucking outfit.
Are you spying on somebody?
No. No.
King,
bro. No.
Why you never told me you had on an outfit?
I said that, bro. That's what I'm saying, dog.
Wait, time out.
Detail.
Time out. This the same chick, though, with the dog?
Hold on. You got to give Bell some context, man.
Give me some context.
Oh, okay.
You a funny nigga, bro. So when I heard you say that part of the story, like, y'all had on the outfit.
Same chick.
Yeah. Oh!
But what does that mean, though?
You wore a costume to go visit the dog?
He is a dumbass nigga, I swear. He just can't keep his
stupid ass mouth shut. I really got a hard time lying.
Dumbass nigga, I swear to God. I got the beep button right there.
Man.
Hey, you really are a brazy ass nigga, though, bro.
Damn.
I said that when I introduced this story on the Ace Boys. Right? I said it was a costume party. That's the whole point.
I didn't
laugh.
But that's not
because in my head,
you introduced it here.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. That was the origin story when you sat on this arm.
No, hell no. That's not. No,
the origin story was when he said he was like going
the first
to visit the dog. That was the origin story.
Nah. You gonna visit the dog?
That was my dog, though.
That's his dog. So
Trey,
give Bell some context.
Like dog, that was my dog. You know what I mean? Was investing to that dog. It was like a whole life, for real.
Man.
That was a good dog, though.
Yeah, it was my dog. And then I kind of like put her. I put the dog on her in a sense. Like, I'm like, you should keep me. She got the yard. I'm moving around too much. I'm like, I don't want to leave him in the spot all day. So I'm like, yeah, do that. But I still want to see my nigga, like, cause I was like,
so you.
That's what I'm saying. But in breaking up though, period.
Wait, King, can I? All right, bro, I got a couple questions then.
I got a few questions too.
Wait, so how do we know?
That's what I'm here for.
All right, so how do we know that you didn't just went to go see the dog that day? You seen Trey walking in that motherfucker.
That's a cold narrative.
That nigga sitting in the car like Snoop, outfit on the DJ, costume. Ah!
You said a nigga pull up in the costume?
Come on, man.
Come on, man.
Come on, man.
No, but listen, that's the truth. All right, so that's, I'll get back to that though, as far as breakups.
Fuck, homie.
Right? So. Breakups not real for, it's like stages to breakups. When is this breakup actually real then?
When you could
be broke up with somebody before?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You said you've been with your girl, how long?
Since 06.
Six?
06.
Oh, 06.
Yeah.
And before that you had a girlfriend?
Yeah, it was so similar, like same time type shit.
Oh, okay. So, but you broke up though?
Yeah, we broke up.
And as soon as y'all broke up, y'all, it was that? Soon as like, broke up or y'all had a period?
Yeah, nah, it was cold turkey breakup.
It was cold turkey?
Yeah.
But in his situation, it sounded like...
But that's the young... That's
yeah, it
young,
had to be. It did have to be. It did have to be. Like, have to be.
Come over here and don't say nothing.
Yeah, it was like yeah.
But she probably was death tapping in. It just...
That sound like, yeah. Well, he was a youngin' when they broke up, though. That breakup
that's true.
Is a different breakup from my man 9 years.
Yeah, that's true, too.
Why do a motherfucker feel away if it's your ex?
I was about to say, you broke up when you could be a...
Because it's like me, I didn't feel no way. Truth for the details of that whole little thing right there, though, because I know me, though. Just like, that's why I brought that story up. I've been that motherfucker with the platforms on. I got the fish in that motherfucker and everything type shit, whatever. I'm just saying though, but
they got the fish in the platform.
Yeah, imagine a nigga like tripping. Me trying to trip.
Hey man. Hey, you really ain't, man.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? But now, but I just feel like it's stages to breakups. You know what I'm saying?
Because what stage you thought that was?
That right
back.
There?
Sound like I'm gonna get you back. I'm gonna get you
it's
back.
It's way more true than details for that though, but nah, it wasn't. I know I was going back.
Buff ass nigga.
But at the same time though, when you got
you invested
love, in yeah, you got love and shit. Like you don't gotta be. You can break with somebody and still like find ways to respect them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But if you ain't went through that though, probably.
That's like a nigga saying, "Macwap, you can't DJ no more." It's like, damn. It's like, nigga, what's my stage of transitioning to not DJing?
You only had one girlfriend, right? Yeah.
So do you think Trey was feeding your dog and all that?
Hey, Tiny is a funny ass nigga.
Do I think he was feeding him? Why you say that?
Because I mean, then it's like that's his dog now. He feeding the dog and shit. That's his girl now. It's his dog now.
But all right, say so, like let's say it was though type shit. I never said that he did anything. Trey, like y'all could stop speaking on Trey like that. He in a whole relationship, man. He said that, man.
This was your ex and years ago.
Nah, this is a couple years ago.
Now you getting specific. I said years.
No, that's what I'm saying.
You added the couple in there. I just said years.
I just posted this motherfucker. The party. I put it on the gram. I was at this motherfucker. Like, you know what I'm saying? But I don't know, man.
So that wasn't Trey dog, though. That's what I'm trying to get to.
I mean, whoever dog it is, the funny truth and the details, you got them stages. When you first got my dog, and you better not have no nigga over there feeding my dog. That's what I'm saying. It'd be like little games motherfuckers play to like keep attachments.
Right.
Then stages to the breakup, then you like, all right, for sure. After all that shit was out the way.
I feel like once you could be around the motherfucker and not feel no type of way, no emotions and none of that, then I feel like that's when you all the way broke up. But if you still feeling some type of way of what they doing or who they with or who they went to go see and all that, then you still attached in some type of way.
Yeah, everything played.
I think it matter how y'all broke up too.
feel that shit was like kind of neutral. It's like, all right, fuck it, this shit ain't going nowhere. Yeah. But if it's like some shit happens, she like, no, I'm done. And you like, nah, man, it can't end like this. Because motherfuckers be having ego.
That's what I'm saying. You get people being their pride, yeah, pride, ego, all like, that shit.
I was supposed to leave first.
That breakup, yeah. It's a lot with that motherfucker. And sometimes you might just, might need a break for a little bit. Man. You feel me? You might just need a break. You never know. But I've been broken up for years. It's been years.
Did you cry when y'all broke up?
Nah.
I asked the homie that, did he cry when he broke up? He said, cry? Nigga, try not eating for a whole week. I said, damn. That nigga was going through. He said, crying is the least part. Nigga, I wasn't eating for a whole week. I was like, god damn.
All right, so what's this big ass uproar about? Y'all seen that that gay Crip nigga? Mm-mm. So it's some dude that they did an interview with over there at No Jumper. He like a gay Crip. So, and it got like all like the LA Crip niggas is one they want to get down with. What's the nigga name with the Brick Baby nigga and all these niggas, because they Crip niggas and they like, I don't know. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, what's
they mad? What's they mad because they interviewed a nigga?
Yeah, I guess. I don't know what the fuck they could be mad at that shit. I don't understand. But
I mean, I feel like at the end of the day, if that's what you're standing on, and you feel like that's what you need to do to please Adam, because I feel like that's who set that play up. I don't feel like that was them that set that play up. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's even more nasty if that was them that set the play up. But I feel like, shit, they just doing whatever he say. And he like,
hey, King.
You know? I mean, it's crazy. That shit. Niggas know what's real. That shit look staged. It look like
niggas just
you doing
to
this shit for no reason, bro. Like, you making just yourself look bad. Basically, that's how I'm looking at it.
Why it can't be dialogue? Why you can't just be trying to learn something?
I mean, you're a civilian, I can't even really get.
It's probably like a code of honor. Hmm?
Did you watch the interview?
No, it ain't no interview. It's just like clip.
Oh,
well, the interview. I didn't see the full interview. I seen like a clip. Hmm. I don't know if it's a full interview or not, but it's just like.
But you're not supposed to speak to them.
Where's dude from?
They say from Hoover in Texas.
I get it.
But I
did not know that until right now, I swear to God.
But it's like, it look off stage, like from the what cut wearing to just the dialogue, it looked staged. That's basically what it looked like. It looked staged to me.
I understand.
It's like it's burnt out.
Like they try to make them, you know.
Yeah, it's burnt out.
Yeah.
But then it's like this guy, like real niggas know what's up. Basically, ain't no real nigga about to go up there. You got shit all on your forehead. Niggas is not.
They really going there with the content. That nigga Adam is crazy.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They doing God, it for Adam. It seemed like that was an Adam lob, but he wasn't there though. See, that's how he on this shit. Like, I'ma just have y'all do it and y'all be there.
So do you think this guy
exists? Adam not in that interview?
No, it was just Sharp and the two other dudes.
Never. I didn't know that. Ah, that shit.
That's
kind
of sick.
It's burnt out.
Is actually a legit thing? Like, did he check out, or is it somebody they kind of just costume up?
It seemed like costume up. I ain't updated on the nigga. I mean, they say he from Texas and shit, but he even what they were saying, he wasn't even updated on what's going on, or he like...
Well, man, shit, God bless their content.
It's like you playing with the shit. Yeah. And it's, all right.
God bless the content, man.
That's on, you feel me? Shame on them. But I definitely feel like they just doing whatever that Adam threw that lob. I hope he threw that lob, because, like I said, it's even more nasty if they went seeking out for that.
Yeah, I didn't know that was it was all that. It was deeper than rap like that. That's wild.
Yeah, but I mean, like I said, it seemed fake. I don't know, cause I ain't never.
Yeah.
I ain't updated on them. Shame on them.
Yeah, man. It's wild, man. This shit is crazy as a motherfucker. My nigga, let me see. Okay.
Tom said, 999. Salute, fellas. Big fan of the show. Big question for King. Was Worm annoying the hell out your ass yesterday? She should be bad, for real, for real. Worm be annoyed?
I love her, though.
Worm annoyed
she
yesterday?
Don't let him get his nerd
or no, she was like, I think she was, she like a big, she protect Terrell heavy, too, so.
What you was picking on Terrell?
I feel like she just like overprotected sometimes, so she was just.
But why was she trying to protect Terrell from
she
you?
Feel like she think I'm going somewhere. But nah, it's cool. I wasn't mad at that.
Do you be feeling like you getting picked on?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Nah, I ain't getting picked on, but like shots? Yeah, shots, yeah.
I did hear you tell Terrell on her yesterday.
Terrell, tell her stop talking.
You said that?
Yeah, I probably had to do that, yeah. I probably had to do that.
Oh, this nigga King was pulling for him then.
Yeah. Hey, Terrell, tell her stop talking. Tell her stop talking, man.
Oh, damn.
Oh, shit. That was funny, bro.
I like Sprite. He said 199. Hey, yo, Sleepy King ain't there. Pour a cup so he could cook. Yeah, King sober on Apollo. Yeah, he sober, man.
Yeah, man, you know.
I like that for King, man. I like that for King, man. Shout out. Yeah, I said 199. Said MacWap a dictator, too. I'm really not.
Why she say that?
I don't know. Yeah, these niggas, they say that because y'all don't be sitting in the front right here in this seat. I guess that's the narrative. Niggas is paying.
We got our own seats, though.
And what's the, I feel like we are, like, sitting, like, up there in the front and control everything. Or just, like.
I think that's what they said.
Bruh. Yeah, and we all on camera, so it don't matter if we sitting right there or right there.
Nah, they really don't, though. These niggas want to do this shit out of camera. Has to be all the way, but. Ace Boy Yummy Bear sent five. Damn, y'all niggas still here? I done fucked around and I didn't know. He said, I done fucked, ate dinner, and came back. This is like a telethon. Shout out Ace Boy Yummy Bear.
Hey, you know what is funny that he said that, though? Because I was watching something, then me and my girl was getting it in on YouTube, and then it was like Apollo came on the fucking TV and shit.
Nah.
So yeah, tell the truth. Go to the details, man.
Hey, all right, man. What you mean?
What do you mean?
You don't
what
tell me.
What was the algorithm? It was the Ace Boys? Y'all was watching the Ace Boys?
It was something. It was something. That motherfucker. It was something. It was something late night. It probably was Ace Boys. I ain't gonna lie.
Fuck. You was knocking, dog. You a freaky, kinky nigga.
Hey, man.
You knocking shit down. Okay.
I
get what's going on.
That shit was uncomfortable. Like I had to turn that motherfucker.
What? Yeah, turn what?
To the TV.
Where was the remote?
The remote was in the window where it's always at.
Oh, okay. So you was able to reach and grab it and then turn.
It was like mid. It was awkward. I ain't gonna lie. I was like, what the fuck?
Why is it awkward?
It's like I'm hearing the homies' voices in the back.
What's the problem? I mean,
it just felt awkward.
What homies? Like you? Wait, so you were smashing your girl watching
Ace Boys?
Ace Boys?
Nah.
Hey, shout out to y'all. Y'all going viral.
What are you saying, Tiny?
He just said it.
Who was you watching though? He never said specifically.
The homie. It probably was Ace Boys in there.
So it was Ace Boys.
Man, I'm up here admitting and all that shit. Admit, man.
Because I'm saying they the only ones that's up late.
Admit. Okay.
You was watching a live show.
It was Ace Boys.
That nigga in the comments still.
I wasn't in the comments.
Oh, so it was a Yam Cam crack.
We got it.
Yeah. Who did that?
Geeked up off the Yam Cam. Baby!
Hey, but basically.
Crazy.
Oh my.
Shout out to YouTube.
Yeah, def shout out to YouTube, man. This nigga Tiny is hilarious.
Yeah.
My nigga Aaron Williams sent two and said King played by Brittany Griner in his biopic. That's funny as fuck.
That's crazy.
That's really.
Bruh.
That's crazy.
Xeno Waves in 199. Would y'all drive off the shrooms for an hour for $10,000? Yeah, I be off the stroke. Yeah, driving, I drive off the stroke. That motherfucker alternative. I'm be all Super Mario off the star. Maximilian 85 cent, $2. Ronaldo Ray gonna play King. Google him.
Is that the same nigga that said Google the other shit?
I don't know. I don't know.
Ronaldo Ray sound cold.
Ronaldo Ray?
Yeah, that sound crazy.
That's Charles Lee Ray, brother.
That's Chucky.
Lewis Lemons at $4.99. If y'all hit a chick, wait, if you gonna hit a chick I was with for 9 years, give me some respect and ask how I feel about it. If not, I assume you a janky ass nigga and can't be trusted. Yeah, that's some wild shit.
I'm saying 9 years? That's like, man, 9 years, that's a decade.
In fact, yeah, that's legally married. Yeah.
So just stay with her if you care like that.
What you mean?
I'm just doing, I'm only being devil's advocate. I'm just saying, but stay with her. If you care like that, just stay with her.
But would you be cool with that?
Kim ain't gonna be cool with that.
But I'm just saying, but I still feel like it's my ego.
Kim gonna fuck you up.
Stay with her?
Why did you stay with her?
Huh?
Like in a situation like that.
What about it?
Y'all got 10 in, y'all like on the y'all on the brink of it's over with.
Yeah.
But would you stay with her?
If on a break and then she did that? Nah, I'm too petty for that.
Nah. She didn't do that, but it's damn near that.
Yeah, nah, I stay with it. And she ain't damn near do that?
Yeah.
We can damn near keep this.
But damn near over when
she's walking that door, huh? So when you after like I confirmed something was done, I'm yeah. But I think it's still ego, so I'm trying to say though. It's ego.
It's ego for you. Why is it ego though?
Because like
you're saying in the relationship over, so it don't matter what she do.
What is it like where do, what does it really matter?
It's called etiquette.
Nah,
it's
I get
called
it.
Etiquette, nigga.
What like what you mean etiquette though?
Break up etiquette, like you said. The stages of it is like
he's telling you.
Yeah, man, it's the stages. Yeah, man, whatever the what you said, like you know.
So you'll be mad if Tiny mess with your girl
after 9?
Yeah, but you already off into a new relationship and everything.
No, like, that's different though.
That's what I'm saying. Most times because you're not happy. If you was happy in the relationship, you was good.
If I'm off into another relationship,
I got you, King.
So if I'm in another relationship and she pull up, I'm like, fuck it, like what can I really say?
But if you're in a bullshit relationship, you'd be hot. But if you're in a some like, better living, you probably like, shit, nigga. I know what this better living feel like. Hopefully, that's that for you.
Are you saying based off? So you saying situational.
If you doing it up, you got a whole new thing going on. It's better living.
Like, what does it matter?
You saying that you just overlooked that?
Yeah, that shouldn't even be your issue to be worried about.
Be the problem.
What if you wasn't?
And then you should have a problem.
Alright, what?
That's probably the best you ever had.
What if
you left him with some other shit, especially after 9? Like, golly.
Alright, what
let's
about?
Just, okay, wait, hold on. My bad, Tony. Let's just say you better living, but the sex is trash.
But your ego again. That's what I'm saying.
How's that ego?
You better living, but the sex is trash. It's crazy.
All right, better living, but the sex is trash.
Hold on, what's better living though?
So better living is everything juiced up. You feel me? You
better living when you just like like you know what I'm saying. You see the future.
I'm
with this.
Yeah,
what?
This like, work out.
That shit all the Jetsons.
But a nigga go home and try to go stick and move, and it's like
All right, then So, but I mean, you can work on that. Now you can work on that with your lady.
What?
Or give you, whoever your ex the credit she deserves. You know what I'm saying? You work know what? I can deal with some more bullshit.
Say pussy fire.
You know what? On second thought.
Yeah,
hey.
You know what I mean?
All right, well, I got a question.
That shit that really got me mad really don't got me mad no more.
You know,
I get it. I get it.
I wouldn't even trip like that.
What about doing business with them, though? Well, not even.
That's still an attachment.
No, I'm saying if she do business with your homie from 9, you get what I'm saying? Like y'all together 9 years, y'all break up, and then she end up doing some business with your
you wouldn't
your
have a problem if you was.
I don't think
good,
that should be an issue.
You wouldn't have a problem.
So okay,
but what if you know like this one of the homies that really be dogging shit? Like you didn't do
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
like,
girl,
y'all
come sign
the
contract.
You know the whole
bitch.
Deal. You feel me? Like this.
Nah. I mean, you know the whole deal. And that's where ego coming at. Niggas get hot.
But
like,
saying,
I know
that,
the whole deal.
But how did that even happen, though? After 9 years, it's just like, damn, now you with the homie. Like, how did that even happen?
You been plotting on the homie the whole time.
That's what it go come off as.
I mean, that's what
the thing is. I mean, both of them know.
That nigga said Kawanga gang. Golly. That's your detail.
He don't really care about you anyway. You should have seen the things he was doing.
You look at these text messages. Look at these text messages. Look what, we was out here doing.
He like, man.
Huh, all right, so.
That's tough. Right.
Okay, I get
that's
it.
A squabble, man. Let's just squabble where you
that's
keep
a squabble.
Yeah. Sure, we just get a little, good little squabble.
But then what
just if, out of respect.
What if it's outside the house? What if they pulling up to the scene together?
Nah, yeah, I mean, man, we about to go to this nigga TF saying, album listening party right quick.
Yeah, the homie.
Now you hating on the homie.
Yeah, I think that nigga TF you got this on party. The homie, yeah, I'm about to go.
Because somebody else that you didn't know could have pulled up. It would have been good for you. I can take that. Like,
but
I don't
it's your
know
homie,
that.
Though.
You supposed to want the best for your homie.
What if it's a nigga from the other side?
That's normal up in the ghetto.
Yeah, man. But I'm saying, nah. But
your homie is different. That's like, nigga, I'm telling you about the problems we having in this motherfucker. You know the relationship. You've been over it.
All right. I got to
learn the bitch.
All right. Let me add this in the mix.
So you say you gotta keep this.
Instagram got your bitch.
I ain't got your bitch.
Instagram got your bitch.
Instagram got your bitch, nigga.
Hey, so all right, what if it's your baby mama?
With the other side nigga at the house like this. Big juices.
Like, do it make a difference if it's
somebody,
a...
Somebody,
oh, you here to pick up your son?
Nah, he in the back, man.
Like, do that make a difference, though, if it's the baby mama compared to girlfriend?
Nah, yeah, for sure.
It do?
Hell
even
yeah.
If it's baby mama for 3 years and girlfriend versus 9 years?
Nah, because he's my baby then.
Not my kid. Yeah. Not my
yeah,
kid.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now, hey, bro, I think you a bitch, so...
That's how I'm walking in. That's how I'm walking in. Hey, bro, I think you a bitch.
For sure.
Oh, my God.
I think you a bitch.
What's up, boy? You just posted, fuck your life, man.
Fuck your life.
Yeah.
Shout out my nigga Dill. Fuck your life, man.
Fuck your life, man.
My nigga Baby Tree sent 199 locked in from Lansing, Michigan. Much respect. I think we've been there before.
Shouts out to Michigan.
Fame Gotti sent, you know, Fame Gotti.
Who?
Bell.
I probably do.
I think you probably do.
Yeah.
Fame Gotti sent 49 and said, shout out my nigga, my brother Bell.
Oh yeah.
Glad
man.
To see
shout
you doing well.
Shout out Fame Gotti. I probably know him by his real name, but shout out Fame Gotti.
Yeah, this nigga just
what's his real name? What would his real name be?
I don't know. But like he said,
I think
like,
his real name Gerald.
Yep, I know Gerald.
You know Gerald?
That's the man, shout out Gerald.
Shout out Fame Gotti. let's see. Now that's some funny shit though, man. Y'all niggas is hilarious.
What you just said a random name?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know you did. But I didn't know a Gerald.
Yeah, I know, and that's Fame Gotti.
Yeah.
So shout out Fame Gotti, dog. I ain't no cap. So Kim, you gotta be going. You going to the Bay tomorrow, huh?
Yeah,
yeah, man.
Yeah,
King Cole, man. Man, nigga supposed to book the nigga tickets up and
yeah,
shit. That nigga just
man, what he do? He didn't respond, right?
Yeah,
see,
golly.
Just like
why
last
he said
night.
Like that, though, Tiny, he didn't respond to you last night.
You didn't either, nigga.
You didn't hit me up.
You in the Apollo group chat?
What you
only nigga that did something that I can't get too mad at TF because he sent the address.
I never had the address until TF sent it.
Okay, what time you get up there?
With the same time TF got there.
What time you get up there?
I got there with Soul.
See?
I got there at like 10:45.
What time you get there, King?
I walked in by 11:20.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, where you? What time you get there, Tiny?
11:30.
You didn't call nobody though?
Yeah,
you
nah.
Well,
that's what I'm saying.
Get.
He's been lying all
he's
fucking cat. Day, man.
He's there's no way I can get somewhere to lie. Like, what's up,
and
I'm on here.
Oh, he's
that nigga said, I wanted to see if the people knew me.
I'm clearing up. No, I didn't pull up. For sure, if I would have pulled up, I would have called one of y'all
that
niggas.
For like the first two minutes, nobody know you. Hold on, let me call somebody.
Yeah.
Nah.
But I really was.
They slapped his phone out his hand. I'm about to call. Get out your hands.
You don't know nobody.
You did throw me off when you said pull up with Q, and then I'm like, I'm thinking that it's one of those you got to walk in with Cud type thing. I'm not knowing.
That's what King told you. That's the only way you good to get in.
That's what he said.
No, that's what type of party it was for sure.
That's the best way to get in.
Yeah.
Because it wasn't none of the you know, it's usually the regular staff motherfuckers that's running the thing at the front. It wasn't them.
Yeah, hey, budget.
That go back to what you saying, relationships, huh?
Yeah, you definitely got
relationships, man. Traffic, so, traffic was there. He walked up. He was there.
Why? It's got to be like that forever, huh? It's always who you.
I was Austin in there, my head, man.
No,
yeah, sure. That's me, really. I could, if I really wanted to go, I could have called niggas. What time y'all going up there? Like, I was just.
Why you didn't want to go?
I did, but I wasn't. It wasn't like.
You didn't want to go.
I didn't want to go enough to be on it. Like, what time y'all niggas leaving? Where niggas at and all that? I did text in, but niggas didn't text back, so I just said fuck it. But I I definitely regret not going though, for sure, 100%. That shit looks stupid.
Even when you like the whole spotlight, the bright light was on, it's like a circle.
Nah, that shit looks stupid. And just like being around that atmosphere, like that's good energy, that's good vibes. My birthday month.
You was there.
What?
Yeah, shout out my boy too.
This nigga about the same height.
Why you put this height though? Like I'm that tall.
Cause that's who you standing next to.
I was TF6 too, man. Looking like
that is his hair right there.
I kept looking down. I'm like, this, cause I'm on the shroom.
Yeah.
So I'm looking. I keep this nigga keep bumping into me. And I'm like pushing this nigga.
It did look like it was all.
Nigga, you ain't tiny, nigga.
It looked like y'all was in the motherfucking what's that shit? Marsh pit. Yeah. It looked like the stage was the marsh pit.
It was marsh pit everywhere through that bitch. Really.
But bro, the nigga looked just like you. Same beard, all the shit.
He growing his hair out too.
Yes.
Shout out my nigga Tiny, man.
I don't know what I'm doing with this shit, but I'm gonna get a cut for my birthday. I don't know if I'm gonna cut that motherfucker off or not.
Water that motherfucker before you get dressed.
You gotta water that motherfucker.
Chia pet.
Oh man,
my shit. It's because I had a hat on, but if I pick it out, I got.
You got some new growth.
Yeah.
Tiny running around this bitch with new growth. Yeah, you know that's right there. That's new growth right there. Oh my god, man. Shout out to the chat, man. Y'all make sure y'all smash the like button. What, he got a stony tail?
You seen him?
A stony tail is cold.
Wait.
I seen him at the slam event. I didn't see him yesterday with his ponytail.
He got he got the ponytail.
Hell no, that nigga extra star.
He got the Drexler.
Yeah, for sure.
Big B
ball Sonic. That motherfucker shiny. It's like that bitch.
He got the shiny star, dude.
No, I'm just saying, like it's
so
he got one of them.
Why?
They said it was over. He got tired.
He wasn't committed to it.
Yeah. I mean, what, he got tired of brushing his hair?
No, that shit was going there. Yeah.
Oh.
You got the COVID.
That shit like peeling. Females lashes for some niggas. You know what I'm saying?
That nigga should have just went to the wrong turkey. Way.
Yeah.
This nigga said
he should have went to Turkey or Terrell Barber.
Turkey.
So wait, he got
Terrell Barber. You sick, dog. That's a dope line.
Terrell Barber? Too. Yeah, he should have went to Terrell Barber.
Oh, shit. That's interesting.
Damn, nah, that nigga said the ponytail. God, that's funny. Yeah, that nigga would probably look like Sam Jackson on Pulp Fiction.
He do look like Sam Jackson now. Damn, that's wicked.
Either way,
how you think that song performed for Q last night?
That was tight.
That was hard. That was tight.
Cud just got energy, even if it wasn't gonna be tight. It was gonna be tight to him.
He didn't know how to do it. He was like, he's been doing it for so long. He know how to convince you. Like, nigga, this is hard. Nah, for real. Nigga saying Terrell Big TD now in the chat. Dude was having a blast. Shout out my nigga Terrell, though. That nigga Dev was enjoying himself last night, man. That shit
he's in the mix.
Terrell one of them people, though, that like to have fun, though. If he go to a show or something, he about to be at the show. He ain't one of them chill niggas. Let me just see. Like, and, be participating in them.
And he was turned up in that shit. Yeah. And it's like a total different environment of, like, functions from where he used to be at with, like, Tiger and shit.
Yeah.
Like, this kind of event was something totally different from that type of scene that Tiger had, like the hip hop clubby scene. Like, so
this was the underworld for sure.
Yeah, this was like real underground type turn up shit. So that was dope to see that nigga. That nigga probably, he showed up like he was going to some whole other shit. Dressed the fuck up. I didn't think that shit was gonna be all mosh pit.
Yeah, nah, for sure. Well, he did that for cause Kyle be, you know, he feel like he was just trying to match Kyle fly.
What he wore to BET weekend?
Yeah, basically.
type shit.
But he had the nipples covered.
Yeah, he had the net shirt with the jacket over it.
Oh my god.
Yeah, the jacket over the top. That shit
done. Shout out to that was dope playing that nigga.
Shout out my nigga, man.
Risk advertisement. Tom Brownson 499. So Keem don't care if TF pull up off the year and hit his girl after a 10-year relationship.
I do. I was just doing, making an argument. I got an attitude.
I got an attitude.
That's what niggas be doing. Mad
the,
about
the,
that.
The pull I'm up mad off at the, you. The pull up off the year is crazy. Ooh, that's man. A cold narrative.
That shit literally hating.
Nigga pull up off the year with your year.
With your year?
Nigga pull up the year. Up the year pull up
got
off
her the year, off the year. It's crazy.
Go ahead and try, go ahead and try this out, baby.
You get in there, try this out. Fuck up. That nigga.
We having a
dance.
That's literally, hey, nigga be mad. Who the fuck you think you is pulling up with my bitch all happy?
Like this.
Yeah,
I'm wide up, man. She wide up.
Hey, y'all seen that shit with that little girl though? That was saying she was dead. Now she ain't dead, and they saying she was dead.
Was she really
dead? Little culture vulture.
Yeah.
How she? Wait. Did she? Hey, but what? If, how she said she TIP though?
Car accident shit.
Ooh.
Why they do that though? Just to get her some attention? Like, what's the?
She was crazy with the attention when she came out. They was pimping her out.
But
already.
That was forced out. That was all pulling strings. That bitch make it go. She dance. Yeah. That was all dance.
But I said, what would that do though? Just be like, oh yeah, just fake like you did.
To get her in the snake, she was on all the outlets. Yeah. Now the rollout.
Yeah.
Mm. The haul outs be crazy, man. Yeah. Motherfucker, go jump off the bridge, man. We got
jump
you.
Jump off the bridge, yeah. I got the
camera. Oh yeah, they just showed that. I seen that yesterday too.
What, King?
With his partner. And they like in the south or somewhere. And his partner, like, leaving, I don't know, leave out their family backyard or something. They just shaded. And one of the cousins said he about to jump off the into the river, off the bridge though, off the train tracks. And he did the shit. The nigga filmed it, it's all on Facebook. And the nigga died. Like he jumped, he was swimming, and then just started drowning. And they got it all on Facebook. But oh boy, shaded though. You know what I'm saying?
He laughing?
He laughing for the most part. Like, man, go that way. Let the fuck, you know, man, go that way. This boy crazy.
Why he drowned? Because he was drunk.
Yeah, they're shaded. I think that's why. Shit, maybe I don't know.
Everybody got fucked up.
Yeah, them currents be crazy.
Oh yeah, swimming against that current. That shit. Niggas think. I used to imagine that I was like just a super swimmer. Till I seen how strong them currents really pull your ass somewhere you don't want to go. That's wild. But nah, that's some sick shit though. Came really filming the nigga death and shit on fucking live or whatever the case.
Yeah.
Not knowing too though. So you think in hindsight? Well, you think that nigga got booked for some shit or not?
I don't know. I didn't follow with that story. Shit, I was hoping that shit was like, oh boy, popped up out the water somewhere.
Damn.
But from what I say, yeah, it's floating around.
Yeah, drowning is one of my worst fears, bro.
You think death by drowning is worse than death by fire?
Oh man, that's what I'm saying.
They both wicked right there.
That's what the shit that remind me of the Maui shit. No, it's like the shit is on fire.
Fire is more. It's worse.
Fire, you gonna feel every piece of that.
Yeah, that lasts longer. That's torture.
You gonna but you might pass out in the midst of burning up.
But that drowning, man.
Drowning, you gonna feel every piece of that.
Nah, like that.
Yeah, you feel every man. That shit.
It's not too much, man.
Not like you be trying to say you gonna try to fight like to save yourself.
So it's either. You plan your death, or you get what you get.
Yeah, you gonna get what you get either way.
Yeah. Me death getting what you get.
If you take your own route, that's what you got coming.
Yeah, but this way, I'm doing it this way. Well, I know I'm checking out.
But what if that don't even work?
That's what I'm saying. Shout out.
So I seen motherfuckers try to, you know, like I'm finna go TIP myself, jump off the thing, and they just. And now they just broke up.
I'm still alive.
Yeah, for sure. They sit there like, damn.
I'm still alive.
Now they just fucked up.
Yeah, nah, for sure. I get it. But I'm saying, though, you people do it. Like, I don't know if it's, I don't know what culture it is, though. But I think, like, it used to be in the movies, kung fu movies.
It's the Japanese. The Japanese, yeah, they smoke themselves. Out of honor.
This is honor!
Yeah, like I fuck with that. If I was strong enough to do that, that'd be tight. That's, you know what I mean?
Yeah, with the little dagger too, just
yeah, let me die honorable.
Yeah, that's sick.
That's sick, yeah.
Hey, Ken, you heard about that doctor that pulled the baby head off?
Yeah.
That's tough.
That's...
Like doing birth, John Q, pulling the head off, decapitating, man. That's crazy. How you even do that? God bless that. Not knowing what you're doing, being an idiot shit doctor.
And that's exactly what I'm trying to say. And that's literally what we're speaking to the smack situation. These niggas don't be all that. These people is regular motherfuckers.
Nah, motherfuckers just be getting lazy.
That's
what I'm saying. The world, especially, motherfuckers be getting lazy. Because I mean, she clearly knows what she's doing. It's just people just be.
People treat, that's the thing too.
Buy insurance, be politics on that shit. If you ain't in there talking, you know, I don't know. It's be just hopefully you get somebody right. You know what I mean? For the most part, everybody in this motherfucker programmed up. Mm-hmm. Then you get a couple people that's just cool. They ain't really all the way. They really care about people in that bitch. So.
That's tough, man. You gotta know how fragile.
That's the thing they tell you to protect the most with a newborn is the nest.
Yeah, like you know how fragile them babies is. Like, that motherfucker brand new. Neck don't even work.
I know I would have snapped.
And then they tried to hide this situation from the mother.
Over with.
They didn't let the mother see the baby. They said they're trying to cremate the baby, all kind of shit, nigga.
And she was in there by herself. No, I was in there with her.
What you mean? Nah, they wouldn't let nobody see the kid.
I'm talking about in the delivery room.
I don't know.
Yeah, I was right there. And I literally almost dropped my first baby. That shit fucked me up still to this day. Just because I know I really almost, you know what I'm saying? Like I had to catch.
Because there's so much shit going on. And I didn't realize it was that slippery and shit. Man.
You cut the umbilical cord?
Yeah. I was able to, shit, that's what I'm saying. I don't know what's going on because I was able to like help pull out both of my babies.
That's some wicked shit, though, man.
I didn't think I'd ever be able to do that.
Yeah, that's tough.
Nah, that shit is crazy.
Yeah, I heard it pass out.
There's like even I don't know, man. Life crazy. This shit is a movie picture. Because it's like do things happen for a reason. They're supposed to happen how they're supposed to happen, but can't tell about emotions in that moment. Like,
definitely.
One is like, damn, you could. You could have been here and you could have went out, you know, tragically some way and that would have been, I don't know, man. I be feeling like when you check out, it's like, it's definitely a blessing too. To me, like, it's like a blessing.
You said what came when you check out, it's a blessing?
Yeah.
Like, it's supposed to be.
When you lose, like, when you transitioning over.
Yeah, I feel like your role is your role, you know what I'm saying? And shit.
Yeah, I feel that.
So, since you feel like that, you scared of TRP?
No, he's scared to get murdered.
That went out a real one.
You scared? Are you scared to go out? Like either way, however it's supposed to go.
I think what it really is, I'm scared to leave without reaching my potential.
For what I know I can do,
where I can go. That's the only thing. Because I feel like it's all, you know, it's just purpose. Like so.
Yeah. I wouldn't say that I'm scared, but I would say. Like, I guess curious. Like, damn, how is a nigga gonna go? You know what I mean? It's a, was it a thousand ways they got to show? A thousand ways to die? Or some shit like that.
I think it's over a thousand for sure.
Well, yeah, nah. I think that, but I'm saying they got a show like that. I think it was called A Thousand Ways to Die. Motherfuckers died and all type of crazy
bullshit.
Yeah,
bullshit dies too.
Yeah, they was at a function. They walked outside. Oh, yeah, it's raining. And they get electrocuted.
for sure.
Like, goddamn.
That's why you gotta just be intentional about your moments. Like, that's kind of like what I be fighting with, just being present in the moment.
Yeah, I live in the past a lot and I'll be in the future, so.
But
it's hard to be present sometimes.
Yeah.
There's just so much shit going on, too.
That's why I laugh so much, honestly, though. That shit really been getting me through life.
Yeah.
So, on one end, I'll be fucking with it, like, wherever I'm at, but I know I can max out my potential, though.
Nigga don't want to go and be like, damn, I didn't even finish it. I knew it was more I should have been doing.
Yeah, but shit, rest in peace to that little baby, man.
That's crazy, though.
Nah.
So what they gonna do with the doctor? Like, she's keeping her job?
They got that lawsuit going. That lady definitely not keeping that job. She pulled a fucking kid head off.
Yeah.
That's wild.
Hey, King, when you say max out your potential, what that mean, though? Because that just was being on my mind right quick.
Shit, man. Capacity, like, yo, doubts. Which is fears and shit, yo.
Cause I feel like you always growing, right?
Yeah, I was gonna say I don't think you ever have a cap.
That's what I'm getting.
Well, I ain't saying okay. Yeah, you're right. It's definitely yeah. You can't max it out, but you could be underperforming. You know you're underperforming.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I get that.
That's what I'm saying.
I feel that.
Like just putting my all into.
Well, underperforming, if you
and my dream.
Comparing yourself to other people though. Like underperforming.
That's where you at.
I was gonna say that's a tough. That's a tough. Some tough shit to overcome because it's always gonna be there. Because it's like a bar, and you, regardless if you, in competition or not, you still gotta surpass that bar or get to it.
But do you set that? You set that by yourself? The things you want, or that's like just embedded in you?
I think with a solid intent. But if you, as long as you. Make a solid effort, then you good. You cool. Should be cool.
Yeah.
That's kind of like knowing, like, unless you're entitled. Shit, hey, I gave my all to that. Everything I had, I felt like, you know what I'm saying? If it didn't work, shit, I'm cool. Keep going.
Yeah.
I'm cool with that potential. I'm cool with me, like, reaching that and then, you know what I'm saying, getting back to it if I need to, if I want to.
Yeah. All right.
That's tough.
Thank you for the clarity.
Yeah. Better live, young man.
Hey, I already learning from y'all, cuz.
Hey, when y'all was younger, y'all had like celebrity crushes and shit?
Yeah, I used to have a crush on Christina Milian.
Yeah.
How young? Like, you talking about like.
I'm telling
you,
I got a crush on Megan Good.
Stacey Dash.
The clueless Stacey Dash?
Yeah, clueless for sure. Yeah.
Okay.
I had a crush on Adina Howard.
Adina Howard was cold.
Yeah.
I had a crush on Patra.
Who?
Patra.
Patra?
Remember Patra?
Yeah, I know that name.
With the hair, the crazy braids, she used to be shaking ass.
Yeah,
I know that
where
name.
Though? Patra where? Face.
Patra, huh? Bro.
Patra where? What she was on?
I don't know. Who Patra, she was, I don't know.
She was just one of those.
Remember the fine chick? King she was on that one sick show, that black show. She ended up being smoked out. She was fine.
She was Dara.
Wait, who?
Dara. I know it's Daria.
Oh, I know you're talking about.
She was, because she played in the DMX movie, too.
Yeah.
She never super crush. She
never die alone.
Yeah. She was cold.
Yeah, she was cold.
She smoked down now.
I love Topanga.
Super bracket.
Topanga fire.
Okay. Let's say you. You got a chance to run through that one time.
Nah, that's all.
No, not the smoker chick. I'm just saying she's still like as it was, but right now. Hypothetically.
She's still as it was.
Like, yeah, when you had the crush, it's that one.
It ain't, but right now, if you had a chance?
Yeah.
That's what life is about.
I nigga adjusting the lights from his phone.
That was something, you know what I mean? If this is something for me, yeah.
But she got some bumps on her lip.
But why you say that last?
It ain't the same. But she got some bumps on her lip.
Yeah, dude.
Why you say that last?
This ain't what I paid for.
This ain't what I paid for. Nah, that's sick though.
This ain't what I paid for. That's
some wild shit.
I like, what's her name too? I used to have a crush on Patti LaBelle and, what's her name? Well, I'm about to call her by her stage name, Claire Huxtable. What's her name, though?
What's about? The light-skinned one?
Nah, man. The mother.
I know her real name.
Cosby. Y'all know her name? I'm hot right now. That got me hot. But yeah, I had some cool crushes, though.
Yeah, congratulations, Rihanna, man.
Tatiana Ali,
she was bad at one point. Congrats, Rihanna had a daughter too, man. Shout out to her. Shout out my nigga Rocky. So yeah, the motherfucking bullets from that Tupac shit. It didn't even match up. I don't know what the fuck niggas thought was.
The nigga,
what they do? What they doing? Oh, they just investigating this shit for just to do it.
Keefy D, he already said he did it, man.
Crazy.
Keefy D said I did it, bro. I already did it. Man.
Come on, Puff. Ain't did nothing.
ABC News has revealed that the body cam footage from the night that Las Vegas SWAT descended on the home of DeJuan Keefy D. Basically, better known as Keefy D's, the search of his home. Amongst the many things retrieved were bullets from his Henderson, Nevada home, which just outside of Las Vegas City proper. Now it's revealed that the bullets found on his property do not match the shell casings from the original crime scene. Yeah, like that nigga would have been a sick nigga to just be holding on to them bullets.
Nah, that'd be them serial killer tactics, that's serial man.
Serial killer shit now, bro. Yeah,
like the symptoms of a serial killer. Like, man, I'ma just hold on to this.
Well, so this the one I used on Pac.
Yeah, these the Pac bullets, nigga.
Like, I wonder how many stories he told that to, like who he told.
Yeah, I know
to.
Who really did it.
look at this right here. Nigga pull out his chain. That shit hanging on his chain. Like, look at this.
Oh, this is what they've been looking for all these years.
This like the real tooth. Bullet right here. That's the one they never
find. I keep this real close.
Oh my god,
yeah, that's crazy.
But
why would he
have that in his house though? If he did do some shit. I mean, they already got like immunity.
Maybe somebody gave it to him to get rid of, and he was holding that shit as hostage for blackmail. Yeah.
And then they told he had the bullet.
Yeah, no, yeah, we know he still got it.
Then, bitch, you the nigga. Killer, then, nigga.
Should have dumped it,
motherfucker, bro. Yeah.
You killer, then, nigga. You the killer, then, for sure.
Yeah, man. I don't really got too many narratives right now. Y'all need anything y'all want to get off before we get up out there, bitch?
Tuesday, my birthday, cuz, so.
Delio! Tuesday, what we doing?
Tuesday.
That's what I was about to say. What we doing? I'ma for sure pull up. We streaming. But then I might groove, too, depending on the date.
Why wouldn't we be streaming?
Because it's his birthday.
No.
And it's Tiny.
No.
That's why.
Y'all never know what's going on in life on that day.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Yeah, see? Shut up, man. Hey, man. But yeah, no, I'm going to pull up for sure, but I don't know if I'm going out to eat or what, so.
We
don't got to go out to eat.
We invited to go eat.
You invited whatever I do, cuz you the homies.
All right.
That's a man.
I don't want to go to no like dinner party though, cause I know.
Man, it wouldn't be no dinner party.
It'll be tricky.
But the party August 19th, nigga. Ain't no dinner
what
party.
What you mean you know how that be? What you mean you know how that be? Like what?
You saying my people don't got chili. Everybody ain't trying to
that's
pay.
What you saying?
That's what you saying? You know how that be? People ain't skipping out on the bill and shit.
He said the bill. Like, I didn't
skip
it out nothing. When the last time a nigga spent out on the bill?
I did that shit.
I smacked party.
Bro, this nigga funny. You funny, right?
You really yeah, Terrell buy your shit.
Oh, you talking about that I did?
I'm just saying, I'm speaking in general.
Oh, I haven't did that shit in a
minute. Who you trying to put that on? That dick?
I don't know. That's what Terrell was saying, nigga. Right?
It's like
how
party niggas in.
That's
funny.
Yeah, King. 50s.
Like y'all did at Terrell Party.
Yeah, I know.
That's
funny. That other register.
Yeah, for sure. I paid for my shit.
I remember that much.
I paid too, because me and King paid the.
Oh, you was over there too, though. You was at that register with
us. Yeah. We could. No, matter of fact.
Where you was at, Tiny?
No, remember the chicks spilled out on
the table.
And she came and found us.
Yeah, that's where I was at.
Found us like, nigga, where the chili at? I'm like, oh, damn.
Yeah, I was really lost at what I walked into, but it was crazy. But I don't know, when the last time y'all did one, what was that?
I got you a cake and a meal, nigga.
Niggas was over there. Let me see the receipt.
I got all my shit on my own receipt.
I got this.
Nigga,
this
was hot up there. It was hot. That nigga took off hot.
Oh,
that's what I'm saying, dog. What is a gift, man?
What is a gift?
What is a gift? Because it's like, what is a gift? I get it though. I get it. Once I'm gonna take you out to eat or whatever the case may be, then you fight the people and all that, and then you take off. Like you started off celebrating my birthday. And you smashing off like that, you know what I mean? Burning rubber.
Oh, he did leave smack up there.
I didn't say burning rubber.
Oh, he did. All the niggas seen was Tesla tail lights in the corner.
Bitch, I said one butter cake.
That's crazy.
Butter cake is crazy for birthday.
Butter cake. Now, before I ain't gonna lie to you, I'm off the not with all people. For sure. Off that but cheap big, shit. Big, what's the name? Big groups? Nah, I ain't
going. It could be a
what's,
big group.
What's the
cap? What's the number? What I'm saying.
It just can't be cheating.
Got, like, no, number it got to be the right group.
Yeah, it's got to be people be, that.
You know, what's the right group?
Yeah, I'm not trying to be with the whole, like, oh, these, I don't know these five motherfuckers. I don't know them three motherfuckers type shit. Like, I want
to,
like,
if get us to 1,000 likes before we get up off this motherfucker.
Yeah, that's a tough one.
Because, yeah, it's over.
Yeah, that's some crazy shit, though, man. Niggas said they seen Tesla tail, like, man, niggas like, is that too real? I looked at it, I said it was a Tesla tail, like, in the corner.
Got out of here.
I really imagine that, though. Nigga, look at the Tesla tail, like, just turning.
Got up out of here. I ain't invite these niggas.
Oh, my God. I was, what the fuck?
Can I ask y'all a question though, real quick?
Silence! Tell niggas like that at the table.
Die! That nigga just slammed the table. What's up though, Bill?
So, shit, I got a project dropping soon, right?
Right.
So, to promote it, I'm dropping content, like, you know, little freestyles. You think that's like, you think if a nigga drop too many freestyles, niggas start seeing you as like the Instagram type rapper?
Yeah.
Like, if it's too much. Yeah. But they tell you to put out content to build a resume. So, like, what's the medium, man? How you find the medium in that? Because how you not become the Instagram rapper?
I think I was just having this type of conversation. I don't remember when, though. But I think the artist was saying that. No, I was actually having a conversation with Ray Vaughn, as a matter of fact. And he said he started.
Because he go crazy, too, with the freestyle.
Yeah, so he said he wanted to stray away from that because he started getting put in the box as the freestyle nigga and shit. It's like, you don't want to ever get put in that category because they gonna mistake you as a nigga that can't make songs eventually.
Yeah.
Cause you just like, why you just making, well, make a song type shit basically. That's how niggas, I feel niggas is perceiving it.
But so how do you bring awareness to yourself then?
Like, you gotta create.
It's so many ways.
Yeah,
dog.
You gotta create.
But outside of just rapping, cause I've been doing a lot. Like, I'm about to drop.
You can start vlogging to bring awareness to yourself.
Okay, for sure. But I'm talking about like talent wise. Be like, okay, I want to listen to the music. Or you think it's less? It's becoming less about the music and more about who you are.
Yeah, I think it's more. It's coming more.
It's hand
both.
In hand.
Yeah, I was gonna say it's both. I wouldn't say it's less about the music. I never say it's less about the music. But
you trying to be like a superstar or like what?
I'm not. I'm just trying to build my little community. I feel like.
I feel like you got one already, right?
I feel like it's growing. I feel like it ain't where
that's
I want it to
never
be.
Nothing.
You know, it's never enough, but I feel like it's growing, yeah. I feel like, of course you want to, like you said, you want to reach your potential. I don't know what my potential is because I don't feel like I've got there yet. You know?
Do you do advertisements and shit?
Yeah, my ads here and there. Not
I feel like that's if you, I feel if you put your ads in the right places, I feel like that's a big thing too.
All right.
Of the freestyles.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Because I know that whole thing right now is like, oh, content. But it's like, you know, the first thing nigga think content is like, oh, you should rap. You should let people know you can rap. Or you should know let people know you are talented. But I feel like.
Well, you could do
but, like. But it's like. My phone, not to cut you off. It like. You know, remember, it's like a mystique. Like, it's a mystique to die. It's a mystique to keep.
But that came over time. That wasn't how they started out.
Okay.
Like, there's mad vlogs of them niggas.
Nah, he started out, and he still know how to come do the push-ups over there.
But yeah, and also that's why Doc got.
If he wanted to just be quiet, he'd just been quiet.
JoJo Ruski, it was the reason for that. You know what I'm saying?
Even F, like it's a kind of mystique to F too. Like, you know.
But he still got content out as well though.
Yeah.
He here.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Like, and on the Apollo.
And I think really, like, just honing in, especially for, depends on what type of crowd, you're going to superstar, you're just, like, trying to just get your tribe.
Yeah. I feel like that's the most important thing, though, to me.
Yeah, for sure.
It like, is, bro.
That's over time, though.
It's really, like, but you got to kind of, like, put some real value on the motherfuckers that's...
Fucking with you.
That's fucking with you. And you then keep on like, curating, just... cool spots for them to come fuck with you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They gonna come anyway. So now this casual gathering is really something now. People coming here, you know what I'm saying? All off
the street. You got Charles Hamilton for sure.
Your personality and they doing the music. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
you can like multiply with your crowd if you really focus on who you got and doing little shit with them, for them, you know what I mean? Seeing how y'all can like mobilize each other. Because that's what it be. Motherfuckers be wanting their voice. They feel like you talking for them, and they be cool with that. You know what I mean? So it's like, all right, build with them people.
Nah, for sure.
What do you think is holding you back from reaching where you're trying to go?
I don't think nothing holding me back. I feel like I'm on the path. I feel like I'm on my path. It's not like no restrictions or nothing. It's just more of like what F said, matter of time type deal. Like I ain't like, oh man, I ain't gonna get here because this. I ain't gonna get here because that. It's more of like a, when I get there, I'm gonna know I'm gonna get there and I'm gonna be there. Yeah. Or a nigga gonna eventually put in so much work, I'm not even really focusing on the finish line. I'm just focusing on what's going on.
Yeah.
And what you think you pushing too? Like pushing, like he pushing everything scandalous. And that's that ass to right the stick you talking about.
Yeah.
So what?
The light.
Yeah, bro.
Right. Shit, people come go, yeah, dedicated to me or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Cause I,
that's, yeah. What's your, what's the brand name?
Yeah, what you feel like you pushing?
Probably like what I've been going through, I could say probably like you know, survival, like coming from something and making it, like, you know, overcoming stuff.
Yeah.
So I feel like survival. I feel like that's what everybody can relate to.
So I think more content like that, you know what I'm saying, tapping in with that, start tapping in right there. It's gonna be genuine, it's gonna be natural for you. You know what I'm saying? You can and whoever listening to you that close, they that and niggas find them.
The day to day vlog shit, I feel like niggas, like if that's your story, just survival, that's
I'm just saying, like survival, overcoming, being from inner city, you know, the typical.
But that's what I'm saying. So with that narrative, that's why I feel like you could capitalize on just the daily vlog shit. You know what I'm saying? Because that's gonna be the story within it all.
Yeah.
Cause niggas gonna, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But a lot of niggas sleep on that daily vlog shit, bro.
No, vlog not, but I think a lot of niggas scared to turn it to DDG too. They don't want to.
Yeah. What's DDG?
Man, he retiring now. He's saying he don't want to do YouTube.
No, that's all a part. He do that every year. He do, that's
what I'm saying, but that's that you could get put in that box too. Oh, this nigga a YouTuber.
And that ain't, I don't think that's a bad box right now.
No, it's not a bad box right now. It's for sure.
I think that's a good box to be in.
Where your corner?
Why you say that though?
That is not a bad box.
Yeah.
Because that's, it seemed like that's where everybody's shifting to. And then if you're doing more than just being on YouTube, like you YouTube and rapping.
Okay.
If that makes, you get what I'm saying? Like you're not just
like on, I could get the, cause if you can't just say DDG, cause I could, you could say Queen Nyjah, she killing shit and she's straight off YouTube. She was a vlogger first. DDG is doing that for engagement shit. He just a DDG.
Yeah, nah, she rare. She for sure. She rare.
Yeah, rare. But rare. I feel like if I'm looking at DDG career, since he started off this YouTube shit, right? For him to go where he at in his rap shit, he's doing all the shit. He's doing festivals. He's doing everything. You get what I'm saying? And he built that audience merely off being a vlogger.
Right,
like,
I get
bought
it.
That
I
attention.
Do.
Niggas, niggas bought it to the DDG brand.
I think it's time for motherfuckers to keep like crossbreeding at the podcast and the streaming.
So
It's just getting to know.
Just like, getting to know. That's what I'm saying.
And they get to see, all right, what is it? Like, are you mirroring your music?
Yeah.
Are you painting? Are you, like, what they going to get to know you? Like,
would that be a disruption too?
Yeah, like, no, because that's like, what I'm about to say. Like, the disruption is when you start, that's really what it is. That's why I'm asking, like, if you got the work ethic, once you start pushing, if it's survival and shit like that, just like the goddamn ambulances every day, they gonna keep that motherfucking ring at the
city. Yeah.
And then you know what it is. Like, I feel like that's just.
Yeah, yeah, that's actually a funny bar. Well,
perseverance. That's what I'll be pushing. Perseverance.
Yeah, but like, motherfuckers will have to see that too. Like, you know what I'm saying? More.
Shout out to y'all,
man. Always be rap. You can definitely do that in several different ways.
Yeah. I mean, I've been working on it too, like doing a little content shit. It's, you know, especially when because, you know, I feel like artists, we put so much. Well, for me, I ain't gonna speak for all artists. Like, making, when you in my position, I would say, like, making people understand, like, I'm talented. Like, I want everybody to know that, so I gotta show that. That's the first thing I gotta put on display. But then it's like, damn, you get lost in that, because it's like, you should already know that. And it's people that already know that you are talented. Now it's time to show those people a different type of thing. So it's just like, how do you do that? You feel me?
Yeah, yeah.
That's all.
No, I get it.
I just want to get y'all perspective because y'all around a lot of great artists, probably the greatest artists. You feel me? So,
but not to get it off you, but that was the problem when Odul sent me the for the shirts and shit. I told you he sent me the bomb picture.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like ETS, Everything Scandalous, and Dedicated, like, those is brands, like, those is what you guys pushing. And I'm like, I didn't feel like I'm pushing. I say her, but I'm not pushing her, like, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I told him, like, it's not you, it's really me. I gotta find what I'm trying to push, and then
it'll be easier to know what type of merch and all that's gonna grow with that. But that what the problem. It wasn't the design that he sent me. It was straight. But like I said, it wasn't. I didn't have that, like you said, perseverance and survival and shit like that, and everything scandalous and dedicated. I just didn't. I didn't have that for him to. But that's why I said we still tapped in. He said when I figure it out, you know, hit him up. But it's crazy that you say that though, because your brand, what you push in your brand, like you said, like your raps and shit, like you just gotta show people that more.
Yeah, but I'd be like, that's because you gotta brand yourself as a, what type of rapper you are too, right? Like, what type of music do you make? Or is that a box that you get stuck into? And it's like, or even me talking about this, is this all a product of overthinking everything?
Nah, but it's cool though, because people go, it's like, now you might get artists that might just tap in with you and follow you right now. Pause. Just because. What? That nigga was muffled.
Damn, what he said was crazy too. Why he say that?
I just say brand, dog. Push that motherfucker, man. Push it, bro. Meek still find a way that he still, dreams and nightmares, he still make you feel like that.
He always do though.
Yeah, he still like find regardless a way to make
people
feel
be
like,
oh, you need to grow, but it's like, I came to Meek for this.
Yeah.
I just, if I ever feel this way, I'm going to go here for this.
Yeah.
If I ever go for this, I'm going to like, you know.
But he can't still give you that as an artist and grow?
What you mean?
Like just Meek, you said, right?
Yeah.
And grow? No, I mean, he's in that lane. He's that lane though, for sure. But I'm saying,
ain't that what you saying, Nobel? You want him to stay that?
No, I'm saying, I know if I need to go get it, that's where
he's going.
Even if
he
grow, I feel like
he gonna still deliver what you want.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of the people
that's
grow.
His brand.
They don't ever leave who they are. It's like you can't.
No, I got you now.
You can grow and still be the same motherfucker.
Yeah, I get what you're saying now. Yeah. I was totally off from what I thought I was here.
Run.
No, that's crazy, man. For shit, y'all. You dig. So I hope we was able to answer you with your shit though, Bell. You know
this is a good game every time.
I'm gonna read these last couple of super chats and get up off this bitch. Jakeon sent $4.99. Detroit tapping in. West Side 7 Mile. Shout out King. What you know about that Sweetwater?
Sweetwater, you know about it. Big trades.
Mm-hmm. Big trades, for sure. The four pack of them hoes, too. Shout out Danny Brown, too, though. That nigga definitely showing a lot of hospitality over there. One nigga was over there.
Awesome, man. My boy Danny Brown, man.
For sure.
Danny Brown, funny as a motherfucker.
He a legend, of course. Like, really a legend.
Hey, how does it work when motherfuckers be reacting to people so...
No, you want to know how niggas be clipping you and shit.
Is that what they go do? Just clip it?
If they don't fuck with you.
They don't fuck with you?
Yeah, they got that. They manually pick that shit. That's how I know Pun clipped me.
Pun clipped you?
Yeah.
On what?
A video when I ran from the chick.
What you do?
What you mean?
How you clip you?
Because he showed it.
I showed it. I was watching the video. Now, you know if you're watching the video and then you show your shit. He showed the screen.
He clipped you?
He demonetized. So he
said like a cease and desist type
basically. So all I did, I just clipped that part of the video out.
Damn.
I was like, this nigga fuck crazy.
You canceled your chili, huh? We need all that chili over here, man.
So if it was a video of yours playing like this and I'm showing the people, they have the ability to clip it.
Okay.
Like, you get what I'm saying? Yeah.
But not the audio, right? Just the video.
Not the audio, as far as I know.
Okay.
Philly 215 said, did TDE pay for Smack? I don't think TDE paid for Smack, man. Smack, he big budget. Mild Money is... I don't think it's a financial issue for Smack. I don't think that's the issue. I think it's just the institution he at. You know.
He needs some high power services.
Yeah, it's just different, bro.
That
come with it too though, man. When you a black motherfucker going to these people, they don't really prioritize you. Like, it's actually wicked out here, especially
your family here all day.
I'm sure his mom there.
Yeah.
You feel me? Mild Money sent too. So you was out here trying to look like Patti LaBelle.
No. I was trying to look like, yeah, I get that.
That's funny. Cali Tree sent $2. Shout out to y'all, man, for keeping us entertained. Shout out to you, man. Shout out to y'all watching, man. Tuned in, fucking with us, man. For real, let's get off Saturday. Y'all niggas could be out here doing it up in these fields. But y'all fucking with the Apollo. Quan 600 sent $1.99. Who gonna keep the Apollo going when Mac leave town? The homie gonna be going up. 3 a.m. sent 10. Shout out 3 a.m. Yeah, man. So I think I'm leaving earlier too, though, as a matter of fact.
When you leaving?
On the 15th.
Damn, for real?
Yeah. I thought I was dipping on the 22nd.
Oh, shit. Hey, low key, what we should do, Tia, we should go to Truth in the Details when Mac gone.
Go to Truth in the Details, huh? Yeah.
That'd be hard.
Nah, that'd be hard.
All right, niggas gonna pull up on Truth in the Details?
We should. My days
that Wednesday,
changed.
Right?
Nah, Wednesday, my days changed. My free day now is gonna be, Thursday and Friday.
Ah, yeah, you good, King?
Thursday, Friday, Sunday,
but Sunday, I gotta go to work.
I'll make sure you back home for Sunday dinner. I'll get it. yeah, no, for sure.
Yeah, but Thursdays are,
I gotta get some cheers.
But you with that, Tia?
I'm with that.
Ultimate Eric Edition.
Yeah. I like that idea. That's what we gonna do for the people. But you leaving on the 15th? You leaving on my birthday, cuz? You just saying that for the people and shit right now?
I'm serious.
Fuck you too then, cuz.
My bad, bro.
How long you gonna be gone?
Till the 22nd.
Till the 22nd?
Yeah.
You going to Berlin again?
Nah, the London.
London.
My nigga Slim coming.
Oh, yeah, you did say Slim coming home for sure.
Shout out my nigga Slim in the field, man. And a nigga doing product shots today.
He ain't doing project today?
That nigga Slim out here getting to it.
That's right.
Shout out to my boy. But yeah, man, we about to get up off this motherfucker. Shout out my nigga Bell pulling up, man. You dig? Yeah. Bell, you got any new music coming out to the people, you said?
Yeah, man, I'm about to drop Normandy Art coming soon, September. After, you know, do some little things. Shout out my boy T-Rex, produced by T-Rex. TF on that motherfucker.
Mm-hmm.
I got Jason Cash, a feature on that motherfucker.
Shout out Jason Cash.
I got some big features, another feature on there. I got Casey Veggies on there too.
Shout out my nigga Casey Veggies.
You feel me? So, yeah, man, I got some good shit.
You got Tiny on there?
Nah, but if you want to, you know.
Shit.
You know,
I do rap.
You can't hear homies get shouted out without you implement yourself.
It was a joke, cuz.
It's a joke.
Huh?
It's a joke.
All right, then.
Oh, yeah, man.
Don't come in on my joke, nigga.
Keem is a funny ass.
Lucky I gave you your chair back today, nigga. Let's get to that.
You did give it back to him in the group chat, though.
Just do it.
Oh, wait. Hold up. So, y'all finna race right now.
Yeah, I did say we're
gonna
race.
I race.
It's gonna be live stream. Yeah, recorded then posted.
I got these pants on. I'll get off on you though, real quick though. But
hey, was niggas one of them little kids that whenever y'all race, you taking your shoes and socks off?
I gotta take my shoes off.
I never liked the get out of the barbarians on the stop. I really ran fast, so the stopping, the slow down, nah.
You gotta run to you. You gotta just slow down gradually.
That's what I'm saying. I really ran too fast. I really ran too fast.
You just like felt like if he had brakes.
Nah, but I'm just saying, I was just dogging shit in the what's the name in the shoe.
Niggas used to think they had wheels doing that stupid shit.
Yeah, now niggas lost their damn mind doing that shit for sure.
Depending on what type of shoes you got, some niggas back.
Oh yeah, that's different though.
Bottom of their shoes like ball tires.
That's from racing.
Nah, that's just probably because you wouldn't got the, you know.
You ain't wouldn't got them, them pale ass Ken Griffey's, huh?
Yeah, you got them bitches. Ball tired. Yeah,
that's funny as a motherfucker. But, shout out to the wrenches in the chat. You did, Kane. I see you, Thizzy. My nigga, Biggs. All you motherfuckers, T Muse.
Congregation Monday noon.
Congregation Monday, man. 12 o'clock.
Justin Fields.
Yeah, funny ass nigga.
You gonna keep saying that, cuz.
Like, Bell funny. Yeah. Bell came in on all bullshit.
Nah, cause you talk about, like, come on, my nigga. Like, funny.
Yeah.
Pull up to the congregation whenever you want to talk about something like this, right?
Oh, he 3 for 3, man. We gonna talk about it, though. I'm gonna call in.
Yeah.
Shout out my nigga Biggs. Big A, I see you, man. We out this motherfucker. Shout out my nigga King, Tiny T, Bell and this motherfucker. Smash the like button, man. All that, man. Congregation
Hot.
Monday. Congregation Monday at 12. You bitch.
And I didn't drink no liquor.
I didn't. I
don't
know if you got that.
You proud of yourself?
Hell yeah, I'm proud of myself.
You should be.
What day? What